assembled here to watch some Dota 2. So, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce you to your finalists on my left here. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Team Ichigogo! Go! And their opponents on the left side, ladies and gentlemen, it is the Druids!
Good luck, guys.
And you're going to be taken through this by your wonderful casters today. Ladies and gentlemen, your casters, Russ and the Kenwin.
Hello! We are here.
Yeah, video games.
Video games indeed, Kenwin. So, we are going to be going shortly into this best of five, Druids v Ichigogogo. So, okay, going in this, we have already talked about their sort of standard picture, standard bans you see always coming out. A sniper, troll warlord, no jug or axe being banned at this early stage, Kenwin. So, a bit of a surprise.
No, I mean, I've seen both teams play both of those heroes a bit this weekend. Mm. But yeah, we've got rid of the heroes that really break the game at the moment. Troll. Reddit has dubbed him ridiculous, so he must be so.
Absolutely.
And snipers, the reworked sniper shrapnel has made him a very viable competitive hero all of a sudden.
Absolutely love seeing the sniper. Oh. However, like anything else, you see that come out and too much, it can get a bit boring. Venge being the first to pick up here. Druids did not ban out the Earth. I'm trying to think of the name there, but I've already making a good start, aren't I? But anyway, I'll move on past it. We'll go through the picks. But looking at the other supports you see coming out here, Lion has been banned to start with, but they still have stuff like the Earthshaker. You've got the Disruptor, I believe, was played up quite well.
Yep.
Mute is Enigma. Obviously, you don't want to be able to turn that into a first pick, but we've got to talk about some of Mute's heroes he's known for. The Enigma, he played a great Phoenix support as well.
Yes, no, Mute has been stepping up into the 4 role this line. Usually known for his position 5 play, as we see with the Watson's Water Storm Spirit coming out. Watson's Water playing his first UK LAN in the middle role, doing a pretty sterling job.
Really, really well. And I got to say, not in the middle role though, in the core role, sorry, but Watson's Water.
Yes.
I thought you said middle role. But we have Storm Spirit out here now, not to call you out. I'm just trying to make look for any excuse. Storm Spirit being the first to pick up. Great hero. You can see him utilized so well, being able to zip everywhere over the map and just give something Witch Doctor.
Oh, we're going to look at it go on the esports stage this morning.
True. Inferticoid did play a pretty mean Witch Doctor. I think we saw two games from him where he was playing that Witch Doctor. And it's a hero that you get the aggrims up, you can win a team fight just that alone if you've got a beacon sniped to get stopped. There's the Ben to swap it out.
Very rare in a year. Yes, and of course they still have 4 more picks to bring another hero with a BKB breaking disabled. We'll see how the Witch Doctor's played, of course, is strong leading support to the Cask if the RNG goes in your favour, one of the strongest stuns in the entire game.
Yeah.
And he has the Voodoo Healing to Voodoo Restoration, which is a strong spell for sustain in lane if they come up against something quite aggro. Druid's known for their aggro laning phase.
Time. Yes, aggro try can be quite impactful, and Brewmaster. Now, I got to say, I'm watching Druids play last night, from what I remember.
Sleep deprived state.
Yeah, I was going to say, they played extremely well. They had like the sort of heroes where they could just go in the link, get the slam down, and try and get these picks off. Obviously, with a Storm Spirit, it's pretty hard to hold down, but you've got the Brewmaster. You could go, I'm not going to lie, we saw Laoi play a pretty great Tiny as the last games.
Yeah, we did. We've seen them pick Tiny without Wisp, which is very unusual. But they don't play it in a traditional hard carry style. They get a Blink Dagger and use it more as an initiator. And an eco, which is with the toss avalanche combo, can do a lot of damage. I would say about the Brewmaster is the guy who played him yesterday had ridiculous luck. There were so many missed attacks. Yeah, Nyze was on fire. He needs to teach me how to have that proc chance on the passive Drunken Brawler, which of course can cause your opponents to miss attacks as they hit you. That free evasion.
Yeah, free evasion, and that's just damage gone out the window. So, looking at the next ban here, Ichigogogo.
We talked about the Mute Phoenix, and it's been banned by Druids.
True, they don't want to face that up. Obviously, with Phoenix, you could take it into the offlane as well as having that as the support.
Yeah.
But support Phoenix, don't value it that highly, but you think about what they can achieve with just that, it's huge.
It's a pretty item-independent hero,
yeah.
Honestly. It gets 6, and then the sun does the same whether you have a Blink Dagger or a Yule Scepter or whatever you want to build on that hero or not. Off.
And
praise
yes,
the Lord. Yeah.
Based druids helping us out now. This is good. But Medusa being banned, you don't want to play up against Ichigo's Medusa. He had quite a Actually, was it? Yeah, it was just Impactful Games. I'm trying to think if they lost one of the games where they produced it, but I don't think that's the case.
They only lost one game this long, and that was when Dreads... No, they did have...
5 seconds remaining.
Yes, okay, maybe they did. So yeah, maybe so not quite 100% win rate for it, but still... Reserve a pretty damn time. Decent win rate indeed.
That was game one of the winners brackets final. They were defeated Dire by the might of pick. DI Vine in esports, making sure not to copyright.
Yeah, you don't want to be dismissed. That was confusing as well. We never saw the Divine v Divine game though. So
I mean, you wanted me to put in the same group. I'm really glad I didn't.
No, that would have. I regret saying that. That was more of a I didn't think through my actions.
You were going to make a hilarious joke.
Probably.
Oh dear.
And like all of my classes, mainly. The joke.
I see
it. Joke from that.
You talked about the ability that Drizzt like to use earlier in Ichigo are targeting that with their bans, taking out the Anti-Mage and the Queen of Fate, both with very short blink spells, which cool, very short cooldown blink spells.
Shadow Fiend being banned out to start with as well, as I was talking about. Yeah. One of those great heroes. If you get the blink heals, Chocolate has played very well. We're going to see the Drow Ranger. Radiant I think this pick. Is the second time we see. I think there was a Drow Visage on day one, but I might be wrong.
I think Rich Gang. Like to play Drow Visage lineups.
Yes, there was a Drow. It was Rich Gang, Kundrel playing Drow Ranger.
And I think I've seen these guys play. They're still the 4L open. They could take Visage too, but this will get in Druid's head. They've already got 3 ranged heroes. The Witch Doctor actually right clicks really hard for support at early levels, and the aura from Drow is helpful to that.
Yeah, when you talk about zoning off lane, again, this extra damage just off the bat, it's really quite tasty to be able to harass with that and sort of smashing them down.
Of course, it also increases the late game viability of Storm. Free Storm up to build utility items, but still hit like a boss in the late game.
Yep, Sand King. Okay,
another
this
favorite
is nice.
Druid hero, yeah.
So I really think Druids are getting the sort of draft they were hoping to, for. The Venge is going to be nice to be swapping like a Drow in. They have.
Yeah, it's an interesting pick, knowing how Druids like to play, and they like this really aggro style, and they're going to take Drow Ranger, who of course loses a lot of her damage if a hero can get in close to her. And all 3 of Druid's current heroes excel in getting close.
Drow Visage,
they do complete
okay.
the Drow Visage lineup. Radiant
team. Hey, it's a great combo. If you can get it, go for it. And I think it's a case of obviously Druids not wanting to just take it to, as a deny pick.
I don't think if it's their playstyle, really, the Visage. No. They're very much a fighty team. They like to get in there. And
I take a Visage by himself as well. Like the Sand King, I feel is like a much better pick here for them.
Yeah, they've got both their supports now, so Druid's left to pick up 2 cores. Ichigo will need their last core after the final ban.
Still the Tiny there.
Tiny is still in the pool, right?
And as you already said, Laue did play it with no support IO to back him up as that sort of stats backpack. But we will see some potential for a nice fight. I'm looking at Soodle's offlaner here, and I'm thinking Axe. Still available.
Axe is still in the pool. Of course, Druids will get a ban before they have to pick that offlane.
True.
Axe is a pretty high tier hero.
We've
seen him banned first at this LAN. So I don't know who else they're banned. They might get rid of Tidehunter. Soodle's played a lot of Tide this weekend too. So that's another hero who could go out of the pool. I'll see Druids still looking to pick up their fourth here. Dipping into their reserve time.
Yeah, they've still got plenty of time to think through this. And I think it's a case of they just want to make sure they get the sort of heroes which can go in, blink around, as we've talked about. I think in the game, second or third, or actually both of the games yesterday, they did have a lineup which had like 4 blinks, and the Abili was there, able to just go around the rest of the map and find everyone. I felt so sorry for Dread's team when they just kept getting these heroes picked off. It felt like they moved as one unit, really disciplined there. And
I think Druids obviously are on their way to doing the same thing. Both Sand King and Brewmaster will aim for blink daggers. Venge can also get one now, of course. They go for Tiny. This is actually an identical lineup to the one they were drafting last night. They take the OD out, Ichigo.
So Druids, as we were saying, it was only about, let's say, 7 hours ago where that was finishing off. So they've warmed up still.
Yeah, they're still warmed up from that game. They didn't need to come in early this morning.
No, and I think this is going to be nice. Drow Ranger, I'm assuming they're going to give it to the Ichigo, because obviously what's his water player? So well, you want to send that Drow to the mid lane, get that level of advantage, and try and get that 6 online as soon as possible.
I mean, who's he going to be up against? She should do okay against Brew, unless Brew goes...
Brew should be off. I think this is going to be a last pick mid for them if Brewmaster goes off lane here, because Nice has been playing it, so we could be looking to see what Chocolate's hero is now. So they ban out the Viper and Warlock taken. Soodle with the Warlock offlane. He's done this a couple of times already, and this is really nice. This might be what they needed to stop the
Yeah, the upheaval, of course, incredibly useful for slowing people down. Of course, it doesn't actually limit blink daggers. They have to get the jump.
I think Soodle may still... he does normally go into the offlane, takes that Shadow at the heel, and then just takes stats. And in a lineup like this, he may skip it. I'm a big fan of upheaval as well, Kevin. I love it.
I'm just saying, when a team so reliant on... They need to get in close to Ichigo to do their damage. And they... Except for they pick up a Windrunner.
This is pretty nice.
So that looks like that'll be a mid lane Windrunner. We have seen Chocolate play that this weekend. So,
I'm interested to see how good these shouts can be, how much they can do here. And when we talk about another hero which is able to run around, this guy blinks in, throws the Shackle out, then this could be disastrous for their team.
If he can grab the core heroes and the Shackles, Watson's Water onto that Storm. So we think we have cooled most of the hero roles correctly.
Yeah, so nice on that Brewmaster. We've got the Iceberg on the Ventral Spirit. Sand King will be picked up by... Element, and we'll see Laoi on the Tiny and a Chocolate on the Windrunner when they have sorted.
We're just waiting for Mute 242 to go on the Visage. Of course, not flying under the username Mute 242 in the client, but that was a rather infamous incident that's occurred.
Yes, shout out to Shu.
Shout out to our beloved UK Dota founder, Shu.
Yeah, he.
Without you, buddy.
He accessed a player's computer, and I believe he did change the official player information. So you're going to be saying goodbye to us. We're going to be jumping into the game right about now, and we'll see what's going on. I'll quickly run through the Radiant. And on the Radiant's lineup, as I said, we've got Chocolat on that Windrunner, Laoi on the Tiny. We will see their Nyz on the Brewmaster, and we'll have our Element playing Sand King and Iceberg on the Venge.
As for the Dire... they're all heading towards the Radiant Jungle at the bottom here, but playing Drought Ranger as Ichigo as they do a thing. Caught it. Watson's Water is playing Storm Spirit. Visage is being played by Mute 242. Soodle on the Warlock. And Infernokoi is on Witch Doctor. And they are going to try and look for an early pickoff here.
So?
Shout out to Mummy and Puppy Druids. I'm not sure. He thought their captain is their talisman. Is talisman the correct word?
I have no idea, mate. But I'm going to say yes, it sounds pretty damn cool. So, shout outs fired around left, right, center. Obviously, Ichigo Gogo do have the winner bracket advantage. They are a game up already, and there is going to be some movement. Unfortunately, as you can see, nothing's going to happen out now. So,
they achieved their objective with that push. Could say that the item they used to achieve it was somewhat wasted. But they've managed to inhibit the stacking capabilities of their opponents there. So I think it's all right.
So bounties either side of the Visage will pick up one, which I think is really important because obviously he might be starved for a bit of levels. And they actually, something we didn't catch at all, they are going to be going into that aggro try.
I think both teams are actually, the supports are top four.
Yeah.
So I think they might be dodging the try lane.
They know the Druid Sursaw playstyle, so Nyz will be down here taking the safe lane and Windrunner in that mid lane again.
I think Ichigo have looked to contest here. They've taken the first level precision aura with Drow, so they've got three ranged heroes. They're already taking over 60 damage as Soodle's gone on top lane.
Yeah, this is going to be an issue. This is always going to be a first bud though. You've got the Warlock trying to stand up against this. This is the first bud. Two Druids in a fight like this. Warlock against three stuns? I don't know, man. Was there ever a chance he was going to survive that?
I don't think so. He just played too aggressive. We talked about how they knew about this aggro tri style of play the Druids like to go for, and it appears that Soodle didn't know about it because he just walked up the lane.
Oh, okay. We see Inferno get some harass off onto Element. Element wants to slap him around a little bit, but a little bit of slap and tickle, and they'll go past each other. Now, Iceberg running around will have a ward up onto him and will be backing out towards that.
Nyz is already sapped level 2 against this. It's a duo lane now with Infernokoi rotating towards top to give Soodle some support because he has no chance if the supports hang around up here. They can just keep killing him. There's nothing you can do to stop them.
Maybe they were expecting, Soodle was expecting Sand King to just go into that jungle, happy to just keep stacking farming. But really, when there's a first spot opportunity and you can farm their jungle, there's no real reason to worry about it.
Exactly.
Now we're taking a fair amount of harass here. Still have some tangos up, and obviously they're just looking to see if there's that stun opportunity. So Laoi's like, okay, whatever goes, I'm taking some harass, but this is still fine. And we'll see Element go to stack up these camps, which is just the standard play. Precision aura, nice for the extra harass, but once more in the mid lane, takes advantage from the win run. Did go for that Null Tasman, which really helps them out a bit. Visit GM with another bounty will be enough to top up that levels. So, Kaya, what sort of early year are you expected to see out here?
It looks like Druids are not going to give Soodle any room to farm on this.
Oh, Inferno gets stunned up by Element. What's a Dwarf? Inferno Queen will be then hit by stun. And that is just a case of Laue coming in, get that Avalanche off with Iceberg and Element. They're able to get the kill. Sorry, what you're saying, man.
Yeah, once again, I think it's just Soodle not Soodle. They weren't really following where the Sand King gone. The Sand King was seen middle, so they assumed he wasn't going to turn up. But he just roamed, he walked up. It wasn't like he was moving. They're going to move the entire tri-lane top now. This Visage is coming up here as well. So they're going to go tri-lane versus tri-lane, but they've already given up two kills. I think this is a great idea. They're going to be a bigger experience and gold deficit to these heroes. Laue can already afford boots on that Tiny. He's being brought quite low by the Shadow Word, but he should be fine. They've not got any regen, actually. He might have to go to base here.
It looks like he's backing up. But this gives Iceberg a chance to get some XP in the lane, which is all right, and we will see a pulls out here. Okay, so they are going to have some problems. So let's just keep the camera there a second. And yeah, we'll look into the game. So the first pause comes out. We did get 3 minutes in with two kills already.
That's
a really quick pause. So
thanks teams.
Thanks teams, they're able to sort their issues very quickly. And hey, it's much better to find out that you've got problems now than in the middle of a
climactic team fight. So.
Yeah.
If we look at the last hits quickly, Ichigo is putting the hurt on Nyze in this bottom lane, but everywhere else is pretty even. Despite dying early on, Soodle has caught back up with the Tiny and overtaken him.
Chocolate is waiting, and we will see something happening here.
They're gonna make it.
And we'll have Nyze just standing, trying to last hit away. Obviously, Drow Ranger being sitting half bottom, potentially quite vulnerable. Ichigo.
They're gonna go here, but Ichigo has boots. He should be fine.
Should be able to just back out now. Obviously, it's a case of
they didn't break the item. Well, one of the heroes here.
Venge was spotted, I believe, but the behind. We'll see some movements. Visage now running away, and that is going to be a hit out onto the Windrunner.
One big punch.
A
solitary punch.
So Element will be sitting this bot ring.
Nyze has gone to the top lane here. He's facing off with Soodle. They are both teams rotating their tri lanes. So it looks like neither of them really wants. Ichigo's team did want the tri lane versus tri lane. Despite their level deficit, they still believe they have the advantage thanks to the Drow Ranger aura.
Well, this could be an issue for them, man, because they keep rotating around. As you said, they've already lost the first part and the second kill. They're not the lead in the last hits too much. Okay, obviously Tidy is above them, but it's pretty close.
There's nothing definitive, but you'd say Druids have taken the early advantage. Late game discussions of this game, I think, are hard. I think Ichigo have the stronger mid game for sure, but late game it's a pretty close contest, right? They have got Tiny, who's a great late game hero, but if they can zone him properly with all these ranged heroes, they have got five ranged heroes and a Drow Ranger. They're going to do so much damage as the game goes towards the late portion, which I'm assuming it will because Ichigo's playing it.
They have got that Drow Visage though, so if things start to go this way, they could start doing the backdoor in as well, grab out a nice little catch and hopefully get some more. But up top, Soodle has been getting stuffed around. He has got his treads, a couple of circuits out, so he's pretty tanky for this Warlock sign up here. Able to get that stats, and as we were saying, he is just going
to
take
that. Watson's starting to be outplayed here in the middle lane by Chocolat. How many losses behind is he? He's 8 losses behind as we see a teleport scroll. There's going to be a fight in the bottom lane. Big two-man stun from Element, Ichigo in trouble. A Shackle comes through and latches, and Ichigo's going to go down. Mute on the run, a nice avalanche from Laue. Right clicks from his team. Looks like Mute's going to be okay, though. The Voodoo Restoration from Inferno Koi doing work, keeping the damage to one hero, but they have just lost one of their primary farmers there. It's a big kill for Druids as they keep their early game momentum rolling.
So Ichigo was the hero to catch out, and really he's the one they want to look for. And we're coming up to 6 minutes into this game. 3 kills already going the way of Druids. They're showing that, we talked about momentum, we talked about that they like to have this sort of early game aggression. They're showing it already, and let's see if they can keep this up throughout the rest of the game. So stacks of the jungle, they're going to be trying to keep that farm up.
Chocolat got that kill, but Watson's Water has used him leaving the lane to regain something approaching parity in terms of last hits. He also unseen grabs something top lane there, so we'll see if he can turn an advantage from that. Ichigo going straight back to bottom, continuing his attempts to farm. The two supports both there to support him still.
And we will see Lowy, go that standard build. I believe he's done this at all the games. He goes straight Midas Rush, picks up his treads, and then goes for that blink. Actually, no, sorry, Brown Boots, and then Blink Dagger, and from there. So, Element's still farming away. We are going to see a little bit of lull as they kind of settle down with their lanes now, not jumping them around anymore.
You might have spoken too soon here, as the supports are going to go for something. They have have great vision here of Ichigo's team. They're going to pause though. Wait, are they waiting for some mana on the Sand King? They are. They are just short of Burrow Strike.
Yeah,
they have it now.
Not having enough to stun there. It's a bit of an issue, and they are just moving their own way around. So, let's see what they catch out now. Watson's War going to be getting that full wand up. Obviously, Chocolate's done very well in the lane so far. Let's see what's coming out to the courier. And that's going to be a Bassi with a TP. So, Soodle is level 6 now. We are going to have the Rock. If there has this Golem dropped in a fight, this could be enough to really change something.
Yeah. Of course, the Brewmaster is also 6 opposite him. The two big team fight ults, well, two of the big team fight ults in this game are now operational. We are still waiting, of course, for the Sand King, who's actually doing pretty well at hit level 4. I think he is the highest level amongst the supports, actually tying with Visage and Venge. Good levels on the Druid supports. But his Epicenter also could change fights.
Yeah, this can be scary for them. If Ichigo takes a team fight, if their spells don't come out on top, they are going to lose a lot of gold and a lot of momentum. These towers are going to be falling, and it's all going to go a little bit sideways from there. So,
of course, Tiny is, even though he's not rushing the Aghanim Scepter, as is standard for this hero, he is still a great sieger. He has such incredible ranking damage early in the game as Mute dropping the Grave Chill on Element, but just to run away from him.
Well, that's okay. They're just a case of they scout out and just run away. And I think, as we were saying, Windrunner, there's a couple of different ways this Windrunner is normally built up, and we can see a early Blink going out here, going up the Aghanim's with a Maelstrom, or just going that Aghanim's crit, which has been popularized as well now. But I still think that the Blink Dagger is kind of mandatory to keep catching the heroes they really need at this stage.
Yeah. We've spoken already about the importance of getting in the face of Ichigo's team, especially the Drow Ranger. So I would imagine he would go for that item. Although he's picked up a Staff of Wizardry actually just now on his Wind Ranger.
That's his war in the mid lane. Does throw out a bit of harass onto Chocolate, but he'll just be standing his own ground. Does have that regen bottled, which is the Storm Spirit rune. So we'll see what they
do. He's not got the mana pool yet to really make best use of it. You really want a bit more 50 mana to maximize the zip potential.
Yeah, it wants to try and just be as efficient as possible with it. And again, the courier will be fine out of mid with that Staff of Wizardry you were talking about. So, yeah, it doesn't go straight for that blink, but
probably the Eel Scepter, of course. Oh, as my voice dies on me,
no problem.
The Eel Scepter, an incredibly popular item at the moment in the Dota competitive scene.
Treads now out onto Ichigo. This Drow is going to get a little bit more damage.
We've got some Bracer Gaming from Soodle. He's got two Bracer recipes.
Yeah,
it's going big.
He's tanking up. He's like, okay, guys, I'm going to get caught a bit. As long as I get my ult down, as long as I can stand in the fight, he's maxed the heal, taken some stats, had one in his Fatal Bonds, and I think this is definitely the way he goes up here.
Yeah.
Drow Ranger hitting 6 soon. This is the important level. Watson's War up top, zips in, grabs the rune.
Nukes the arrow as well.
Yeah, nice little.
And the regen rune actually in effect. He's gonna make a go.
Zips back. Doesn't even
just run out of mana. He was just one mana point short of the pull.
Oh, that's a shame.
Chocolate went to the high ground, so he just missed out the opportunity there.
And he does lose the regen as well now, so he's forced to use the rest of his portal charge here. And he's going to go down bot and try
he's
and
gonna
just...
He's going to get both runes, actually. That's big from Watson's.
So let's see what they can catch out now. They do go back, and we'll see Ichigo still farming up, is level 6, and this damage is now going up to 27 for their whole team, might I add. And this is now an issue for Mute. Gets hit by the stun. Lowey comes out, throws the stun out in Photocoin. Photocoin gets the cast off, actually passes back to him, which helps him out a bit. Then I'll turn it on to Lowey. Lowey could be in troll. The frost arrow is enough to slow him down as he goes to run away. Remember, he has no boots. And that puts Ichigo on the scoreboard. Now there's going to be a ball going for Venge. This could be an issue if they decide
wary.
To go for it. But yeah, they're wary. They know that people are missing
from that. They've got this in the woods here.
Yeah.
So they saw the oncoming reinforcements in the form of Nyx and Chocolat. But yeah, that's a big kill, actually. He just brought his Midas too. It's on cooldown now, so he's not actually hurting his efficiency too badly.
Mm.
And he's got his brown boots, actually, just now. So he's not doing too terribly off that, but that's a big kill for Ichigo. They're stalling the momentum, which, as we keep saying, is important for Druids in this early game, because they will be a bit of a deficit in the mid game, I think.
It really is, and I've got to say, this Sand King's going to be having that blink down soon, so Element will be able to come in. 3 assists onto him at the moment. Checking out the hero levels, we can see, kind of to be what is expected, this tri lane, they did have some issues, so Radiant's the Witch Doctor has been rotating around, getting whatever he can, and he pays for it with his levels. So level 4 onto him. Visage has just hit level 6, so maybe we could start
we'll follow. He just got a creep in the bottom lane, and he's 6 as well, so we have the epicenter online.
Okay, this is very nice. Potential for them to take this down. And yeah, familiars flying around the map and can be murdering people left, right, and centre.
Like they're being heading to the bottom lane with his familiars here. Is you are slapping XP middle. Of course, an interesting hero in that he can play a support role with just these birds here, who both, of course, bring stuns and a large amount of damage to the table in the early portion of the game.
Link Dagger now up online, and let's see if they can make that catch. 013 onto the Tiny. There is going to be some...
That's a really fast Blink Dagger, actually, considering how efficiently the jungle was warded at level 1 by Ichigo. Element's done incredibly well. I mean, he's got 3 kills participation, he's not died once, and looks like they're going to maybe attempt to... I think the edge of the smoke was just caught by
the ward, woods there, yeah,
so Ichigo saw it and is backing off with his support hero, so that's a waste of smoke.
They, unfortunately, yeah, not realising that they got that.
I don't think they saw the Blink on the Sanky, so I don't think that's been revealed yet.
Well, that's something at least. They're obviously not...
They're going to actually rapidly rotate... Oh, Sanky is anyway. Sanky and Brew both heading towards middle quickly.
Now, Element could go and make a catch. Here we go. Here is your epicenter. Goes to Blinken, does lose a bit of damage, and now it doesn't get the stuff, but now Visage Mute is going to be in trouble. The Windrunner just all attacked him down, and this Visage is just taking a lot of damage. Actually, Stick Charge is enough to keep him up, but he's now going to get Power Shot out. Unfortunately, that would have been pretty hard to dodge that at that stage of the game, but hey.
Sudo not coming to fights with that incredibly strong game team fight ultimate. He's just gonna kill buildings. And he's gonna go for that Aghanim Scepter now with his 2 braces finished.
And look how tanky this man is. 1,547 HP. 2 8 braces armor. At a point booster. 8 armor. This guy is a pretty tough nut to crack.
Yeah, and of course, actually taking for 150 hit points of damage at the moment, thanks to the Collision Aura from Jara Ranger. Jara, of course, when she hits 6, gets a nice boost from her marksmanship, nice free damage coming in. So.
This Warlock is a really important factor, which hasn't come to a fight yet.
But he's doing work in the top lane. He's CSing nicely after the earlier troubles he had. He's actually second leader on the charts, just behind Watson's Water. 31 denies as well. He's been starving out his opponents in that lane.
So what would you say about the potential for that first epicenter? Because that's the epicenter which was the Blink Dagger reveal.
Yeah.
It wasn't that big, but they got a kill for it, right? So that's not the end of
it. It was a good reaction from Watson's.
And zipping as Element goes for it. Whoa, Watson's Water. That was a close situation there, and that's just enough to save him out.
It's a replay of what happened on the first epicenter, except Sand King saw him zip and cancel his epicenter, which was big. Mm. I don't think it's not a high enough level, of course, to have full ranger. It wasn't at that fight, it was only level 3. I think he just misjudged the distance on the blink and gave Watson's a second to trigger his zip. Otherwise, I think that was probably a double kill for Druids instead of just the Visage, which they picked up.
So Tiny has got those dreads up now. He's going to have gold onto it, still with the Midas, and let's see what he can catch up here. The Ancients will be getting farmed as much as possible.
Why are we having not such a spectacular game on this Tiny? His farm's pretty slow. They've got 2 heroes with over ATCS on Ichigo to only 1. On Druids, if you look at the network, only there are 3 heroes in the top 4 for Ichigo's team.
So although, they might be behind on kills, it's only 3 kills, and as you said, they have kind of got the farm on lockdown. So as long as Ichigo could stay in the game, this could be enough to keep him going. Birds coming around, flying out, harassing down Iceberg. Just turns around and gets a couple of hits.
He might get this. Oh, no.
So now, and in the mid lane, that cast going back to him. He's not going to commit.
Still being hit by it. He's not actually got. He's not been hit by the Maledict. He would have died if he had Maledict on him.
Yeah, it's only level 1 Maledict, but he was incredibly low. So, okay, 2 TPs forced there.
Yeah. So it's not what they wanted. They wanted to kill the Swimrunner, who is worth the most gold of any of the heroes on the map at the moment.
In the mid lane, Watson's Ward zips back to the tower.
Got the Blink off though. Well played.
Yeah, it could have been caught there, so Element's just making sure he stays.
Ichigo's going to get this tower in the bottom lane, I think, though. They force the glyph. Ichigo and his birds all in situ. Of course, the map space is full of Nora, so those birds now hit for almost 100 damage.
Oh, there's the shrunk patch of the TP, but that doesn't really make a go. It's just, okay, use that TP, stop him from farming elsewhere.
They didn't get the latch. If they got the latch, maybe.
I'm in the mid lane. This is Storm Spray again. Kohalia, Watson's Ward could get away thanks to that cast stun. And now this could be an issue. There's going to be Element going down. The cast still bouncing. And that auto attack is enough to get him down. And now there's going to be Iceberg as well. And Ichigo getting a double kill. Turning that fight. It looked like a Watson's Ward might have been dying, but realized he could turn it. Come back in.
Great call from Watson's to turn on that. He was incredibly low, under 100 hit points at a point there. But he still turned around. He went ham. Achieved everything you could have hoped for. He'll back to full HP there. He sits behind the tower. They're going on Chocolat, but the split from Remaster. Watson's feet, so hasty retreat. The silence from Ichigo is too late. Chocolat's going to live, I think. He's got Fatal Bonds on him. The Rootlings going forward. They get the tower. Laowei comes in, gets a nice two-man avalanche.
And the birds are still attacking him down. Laowei in trouble, will die as well. This is really not what they're looking for. Now Element blinks in, goes to get the episode off. However, Watson's Water grabs him off the map. Silence connects onto Dice as well, and he cannot get anything. He's going down. It's four people dead.
It's five. I mean, he's respawned, but they got all five heroes dead down in that
check
fight.
Check this fight recap,
not a single hero dead for Ichigo. And look at the XP change. That's a lot. If you look at the graphs for an even more personal image of how far ahead Ichigo have managed to pull just from that one victory. We talked about momentum and how important it is in this current patch of Dota, and right now it's all on the side of Ichigo.
And we said about Tsuda being a tanky chap. He's there going to just say, okay guys, let me have that, and we'll be going for it. So let's see what's going on here. There will be just the carrot flying back, and now there's Roshan towards the Storm Spirit. Watson's Water gets that. Unfortunately, Druids can't really take that fight after all dying. They still had a split on cooldown, no epicenter, and this is
the right call to get involved. Laowei is getting close to his key item, though, as we talked about earlier in the game, the Blink Dagger only 300 gold away for the Tiny now. So maybe they can try and make a turn, but that fight has compounded the farm advantage that Ichigo already held. The top three now, all heroes for the Dire side in this match.
Aghanim's up 18 minutes and 40 seconds. Wow, this could be a...
They gave the safe lane finds to the Warlock, and he's starting to pay it back now. He did finally turn up to a fight, and he picked up three kill participations in that fight. Did he actually drop the rock, though? And I think he did he?
It was on cooldown from earlier. I believe he used it in one of the fights.
To push a tower?
Yeah, I think it was up top. And now Watson's Ward tries to zip in. They're pretty mobile though, so they will run away. It was the full stuff he has gone in, but he's now gets Vortex back. Element just gets that blink, the stun off, and obviously he's blinking for three more seconds. So the tower mid, 188 HP. They're going to still be standing. They're okay right now. Laowei blinks in, gets the stuff on Sudo.
He's gone really aggro there, man.
Oh. Yeah, that was a... it's one of those ones where he does have his team pretty close, and remember, they have the blinks, they have the potential to get a catch.
All five heroes middle for Druids. The Ichigo lineup splits across the map. They're actually going to head towards the jungle. Going to try and catch out Mute. He's trying to finish this bottom tower.
And Nyze really wants to try and finish that lane. 1,700 gold. He is quite close. But able to be sent around. And Mute, 215. Building the Aghanims. Has got Medallion. The birds are just taking Laowei's time. It feels like Ichigo are still really confident. They knew they had to wait for a bit. So they were like, okay, guys, we'll just keep farming. And it's just good. Would you say discipline?
Yeah, they've played well this game so far. They know they can beat Druids. They pulled it off yesterday. A two-game sweep in a best of three, the winners bracket semi-final. This rematch, of course, you see Ichigo already have the one-game advantage due to their position as winners bracket victors. They are showing that they have, despite the lack of sleep everyone here at LAN is suffering from, they have not lost a step thus far, at least, and could be moving towards one game of the £2,000 first prize.
And we will see if this could be their first step towards it, as you were saying. I like what this visage is doing down here, just farming up, keeping these birds around. We have got no precision orb for 20 seconds, and this is 11 drow now. 51 damage up there up top. What's Sword zips in, catches out Laowei. It's going to be the TP rotations, and he finishes him, goes right away, has got that Aegis still, and it looks like this is just going to be what's Sword getting
TP.
A free kill.
That was the problem. I mean, even if he'd got there in time, he's not going to stop him at this point. Chocolat just didn't do enough in the game. Sudal turning up to support him. If the Chocolat hangs around, he could be in trouble now. There's a rotation coming from the middle lane too.
Watson's Ward just showing why this hero is so damn good. You just go in, catch him out, and now there's got to be some rotations. Windrunner with that haste ring. Power shot
is clipping. Will they dive? I don't think they can. I mean, Nice has finished his point back. Radiant's top
tower. We're not, with Lowy dead, this is really quite a struggle. I think they've got to lose the tier two.
They're going to try and defend it. He's the glyph. Spamming a power shot from long range is the wind ranger. They don't have anyone else to.
Yeah, Walter's Ward just going to be slamming down. And as we said, there's the Aegis on him. Right, Nice does have that blink. There could be something here if he gets the blink catch. There's the avalanche and your toss. Remember, this is all for an Aegis. He still has the Vortex off before he goes down. Nice. Blixin gets his split off. There has been the rock dropped. And Ichigo is now going to be coming back, trying to just focus down these Brulings. And they can take this quite easily. There's the Air One gone. And they are trying to focus it down. Now, go for more Walter's Ward. Didn't die at the front lines. Able to go back. And
Tiny
this Panda.
About 20 hit points there. Just got
yeah, that was the storm zipping in afterwards. So the tier 2 was taken. There was two large cooldowns taken either side. The Brulings for, well, the split for Brewmaster, and obviously KO Covering for Warlock. So, in the mid lane. Let's see if Element can get more there. That's a two-man stun. Nice to see.
He's really low on HP though. So he couldn't just stay in channel because he would have been right-clicked down by the Golem.
And especially a smart call because they had sentries on them as well. So just don't go for it. Just get that one stun off. Disrupt their sort of push and then back out. This Golem is still standing, but they are just going to try and avoid it.
So the boss thing's already finished on this Storm Spirit at 20 minutes. He's got half an Oblivion. He's got one Oblivion staff pretty much finished. So one Oblivion staff is finished, and the next one is done in 200 gold. He's nearly got an Orchid Malevolence. What's the name of that item?
Well done, man.
It's been a long weekend, friends. Yeah.
And this is game one of the best of five today. Looking at the graphs, we've been talking.
Technically,
it's game two, but the winner bracket advantage is Ichigo. If someone's just joining us, they'll be like, oh, have I missed a game already? So you're just trying to throw a spanner into my way. Do you know what?
See if I can frustrate the stream.
You'll frustrate me if anything else. You'll be going for a table. 10k XP towards Ichigo at the moment. And looking at the gold, it's over 10k as well. So they have got that. They have got that advantage, but we knew this was going to be the case, and it feels like Druids are like, okay, guys, we need to step it up, try and get something. And Lowy playing a very different Tiny to what we saw last night.
Yeah, he's just not had the. He's not been left to farm. He's not had the same. He's not had the same game impact, has he? He's got three kill assists. Those are the three assists his supports put on a plate for it very early in the game.
And he could try and put a bit of tower pressure to Sulu. Signing back, just bombs up the creeps and pushes them down quite quickly. Crow Ranger, standing behind. There's 26 seconds on this cooldown. Storm Spirit will have that on him. And there will be a chance for a play to come out. So, Chocolate did go for that Maelstrom, which is pretty damn nice, because obviously just with that and a Shackle, you use your ultimate, it's enough damage to kill pretty much everyone on this team. But maybe apart from Sudo during the Shackle duration, he is pretty tanky.
Sudo, 2,000 hit points now with the item scepter finished, 11 armor. Yeah, I think you'll struggle to kill him, even though that Windrunner is now hitting something approaching real damage. Notably less than Sudo still, thanks to that precision aura, Sudo up to nearly over 170 damage.
Yeah, it's a weird one, because it's not something you expect in the fight. You're like, okay guys, we need to be careful with the warps, right clicks, but I suppose with the stats and everything else, has got that Fatal Bonds maxed up now, so there's six targets.
I mean, on the other side, most of the druids are pretty tanky. The Sand King's a bit squishier than he needs to be, perhaps, but with Windrun, with Tiny's bigger health pool, and with, of course, Brewmaster's natural tank ability from Drunken Brawler and Split, the right-clicks aren't the most significant part of Warlock's kit still, but they have to be aware of it. They just let him right-click the whole fight, he will kill someone.
Okay, and we'll see the lads.
Yeah, this is the support Brewmaster build. Did he do this last night?
Well, I think this is the right call. They need something to help bolster their team. And he did in one of the games, but I may be wrong. My memory is not this good off this. So, 26 minutes coming to this game, 4-8. Although you might say, there's not that many kills at the time of the game. They've all been important kills. It's been Druids getting that initial burst of energy going into this first game. And Ichigo, they've come back.
Yep, they've... I mean,
although you could argue they never really left. Farm wise, they never left. Kills are up top once more. We'll be able to start now. Lowie comes in as well, and they just absolutely destroy him. Nicely done there.
That's an important kill. It is Bloodstone. He only actually got one additional charge in it, so that's really stymied the momentum of that item pickup. He's down to 6 Bloodstone charges, which is below where you start on this patch, isn't it? It's 8 at the moment.
Yep.
So that's a pretty big kill. They're going to try and turn it into a tower. It looks like Ichigo are thinking of trading.
Well, I think this is the right call. If they've got to lose a tier 1, let's get a tier 2. Fortification now forced. There's going to be a TP back. The birds will scout it. Stun used a little bit early, but that's one catch. And that science did not connect there.
They're coming here. They want to fight.
But yeah, they could be going for this. Everyone and their mother is TPing down. Now Nice comes in, gets the split off. And now Ichigo throw it up into the air. Okay, I'll go for him. We'll buy him a bit of time. He has got the BKB, but he's still getting focused down. And the Brulings can't be enough. Inferno Coin will be swapped from the Spirit. And Wolf Swarm will be going for these kills now. And it looks like the Druid. Maybe going down, and Ichigo's still in the back line. He's going to be going down to this Bruce, but no, he's not. They've managed to finish it. Brewmaster doesn't get the clown for time, and the heals, Witch Doctor, and your goddamn Warlock is an issue. Element No going down as well.
Only Laowei surviving for Druids. Watson's Water, of course, the Bloodstone still decreased his respawn time quite significantly, so he came back into the fight, TP'd into the tier 1 top, and just zipped to the jungle. He had no mana. Guy still right clicked to stay much, thanks to Jawara, that he was a relevant hero. He brought his Silent Stick as well, that's finished. So, the Bloodstone actually doing the work, despite me saying that it's better to fight this time. They are going to get the first racks of the game,
27 minutes into the game. This is not what we normally see from Ichigo, but they are bringing their A game.
Thanks, Ichigo.
We are always grateful. Blink Dagger now out there, and Aghanim's for the
third bird, of course, even more efficient with the Precision Aura. Damage shared out.
I gotta say, that was really well played from Ichigo. Ichigo able to stay alive, had his BKB up, obviously his team as well. Inferno Coin, which told the Voodoo Restoration was turned on, healing them up. You have that Shadow Word from Soodle, the Warlock, so much healing. It was kind of like, guys, how have we not killed him? He went down to, I think it was about 100 odd HP, and Ichigo just.
It's the second fight where a key hero has just not died for Ichigo. We saw it also in that fight where Watson's skin of his teeth is way too. Survival.
And Roshan again falling to them. So, Storm Spirit with the Aegis.
Aegis is such a great item on Storm, of course, because it gives you a full mana pool when you respawn. Storm, a really mana hungry hero.
Do you think that Storm. It looks like he's going to be getting it now. I was about to say, do you think that Storm needs to buy this BKB right now? Because obviously they've already got a rack, so he might be feeling more confident. But if he has that BKB.
It gives him.
There's so much lockdown. If one person catches him, he should be dead.
We saw what happened when he died at Top River just a minute ago.
True, and this could be where a tower could be falling for Ichigo. Druids want to try and push this. This will be their second tower of the game, and there's going to be a TP rotation up here. This movement, and I think Druids are going to make the safe play. They're just like, okay, guys, let's go now. Lowie trying to build up that Aghanim, so actually he hasn't got it now if he wants to buy it, but. Another team fight, we could be seeing another Rax going down.
Yeah, I saw this tier 2 middle, so Druids will be confident of staying in the game after the next team fight, but they will, when it says in trouble, is Watson's Water's just going to zip his way around the map.
Aghanim's rolling in for Tiny, this could be the difference to get the cleaves off, you know, to make that big physical slap.
Of course, still pretty slow. The Midas does offset it a little bit, and the Treads, of course, but compared to a Tiny in the same position with a Wisp.
Yeah,
he's not going to be the monster that many people are familiar with Tiny, not the Lanham Tiny from the International 2.
That Tiny can be a mountain smashing down your base, and there's now
a mountain giant,
yeah.
A giant mountain.
Literally a giant mountain, and there's now going to be a Yule's out for the Sand King, which could be pretty nice. Obviously, they could cancel these in Fertigrate, and now there's a zip in. Once more, we'll be killed with a stun.
Watson's going ham.
But he really doesn't care.
Yeah, no, he's got the Aegis. He's just. We went in solely to let them kill the tower. Inferno Coin getting the last hit with his 120 base damage. I guess, you can't really joke about support stealing losses from carriers when they all hit for best part of 150 thanks to Drow Ranger.
Yeah, they just want to get that down. I think. Do you want to see Drow Ranger not go? Oh, Watson's War goes in for the catch, grabs Element. This is going to be a really annoying for him. Science Throw now will connect onto the Windrunner, but now Element gets the start off back onto Watson's War. Watson's War has got his way. The split has come out, and Ferdicoy will go down. Soodle was put in the air, and now they're trying to focus down Ichigo. Ichigo did pop his BKB, and now there is your Golems. Watson's War still standing, has got that Aegis, and This visage will send the birds onto the bench, but not be able to get them down. So they want to try and fight this. Remember, no split. Epicenter's down for 30 seconds as he's dead, and they need to just try and do something. There's the Drunken Haze thrown out, seeing if they can get anything. But this Rax goes down. You said about that tier 2 in the mid lane, but they already take the tier 2. Go for the melee Rax, and can Druids do
this
anything
game,
in this
stage? I don't think Druids can stop this. What do they do? They don't have split anymore. They have nothing to still fight. They need the Sanctum to be alive, and they need a massive, massive Epicenter. But there's a silence. Oh, here comes Laowai. They're going to blow up the Aegis only on Storm Spirits. He's coming back.
Oh,
and now
no, Laowai
in trouble. Nice swap, but he still dies to the Soul Assumption. Iceferg on the fleet fleeing, but he's going to actually have a stun of HP. That's good. Fatal Bond's in effect, though. He's going to go down anyway.
There is GG. Nice shackle there at the end, but I'm afraid Ichigo able to take that first game.
Yeah, round of applause for our teams as we finish game one of these finals.
Yep.
Ichigo moving to a 2-0 advantage in their winners brackets.
Victory there.
Yeah, well, not really we expected with such an early game aggressive, but the Drow Visage showing why it's such a deadly combo, and one you might not want to go against.
Yeah, I mean, Ichigo maybe benefiting from their reputation as late game gamers, they're picking a relatively early game oriented lineup and delivering on it.
Yeah.
Perfect execution, pretty much. Had a brief wobble at the start with the lane switching where Druids looked like they got an advantage.
A very small advantage, but still they had the very early game. Get that off, able to go into it. So I believe we will be taking a very short break.
A short comfort break whilst the players take five. And then we'll be back with game two of the Emerge Dota 2 finals here at Insomnia 54 at the Rideau Arena. It seems that Druids, Ichigo found an answer to Druids' aggro style. They have not taken an app off them all land. This would be the fourth time they've played. Maybe it's fourth time lucky, though the saying is always third time, and it wasn't in this particular occasion.
They need something. Exactly the same bans out now. Ichigo banning out the Shadow Fiend and the Troll Ward. Obviously, as well as Shadow Fiend being a great hero, Chocolate plays a pretty mean Shadow Fiend, so maybe...
That's identical bans from the first game. The exact same hero is taken out of the pool in the first phase, and now Ichigo... getting the first pick this time.
Yeah, that's be interesting to see what they go for, because obviously this sets up the rest of the draft to see what they want to grab.
And also telegraphs to Druids what they might be after. It depends what they go for. They might go for a flexible support hero who can fit into several lineups. Or they could pick a core and maybe indicate what phase of the game they're going to look to come online and start rolling all over Druids.
So, pick one out here, and it's Uijdoctor.
It is that flexible support hero.
Fanagoy played a nice one last game.
It's a versatile hero. Those heals, of course, very helpful. And see, will Druids do anything different? They have the same options open to them, but are they going to be happy to pick a similar lineup? But no, they are going to take Watson Storm from him with a pick.
It's very annoying to play against. You could be standing very far back, not even see Watson's War. He's zipped in from across the map, gets you out. You've got your heroes coming to try and catch him, and then you blink forward if you have your blink by this stage, and.
He's gone. Yeah.
Yeah, Storm's already gone.
And the Earthshaker, the mute phoenix coming out. We've got the bird. I hear the bird is the word.
Well, everybody has heard about this. But phoenix. Hey, there's this actually some versatility. They could give it a Soodle, but I think giving mute the support phoenix would be the.
He's played it. I think he's played it more this time. I've seen Soodle play it once, and I've seen mute play it more.
I've got to say, from what I saw of mute support phoenix, it was quite tasty. So, also another thing you. Got to think about is when you have the Phoenix, if you take him off lane, it's quite easy to certain heroes could be utilized to shut him down. So, obviously, not taking him to that lane at all, you don't have to worry about it.
It's true. Of course, then the question is, how does he get his farm? He is pretty item independent, as we discussed, but he does still need levels to be an effective. Is it a she? It's the bird.
She? I'm going to say she.
Yeah, the bird needs its levels to do its thing. As we see the bans coming out, Druids taking out Medusa again, thank you guys, and Magnus, the big team fight controller taking out the game. I've not seen much of Magnus this line, though. Ichigo tell me that they want to scrim against Druids playing Magnus in the 4 role. So perhaps that's a target ban.
Yeah, that would be a...
Interesting, I think is the word you're looking for.
Yeah, interesting. It is a little bit different there, but Druids Esports looking at their third pick now. They've already got the Earthshaker. We'll probably get that next.
It's probably also a reaction to the that ban on the Silencer, suggesting that maybe it should go going for the Wombo in team fights. Mm. They already have two big team fight ultis in the Death Ward and the Sun Supernova.
As we all know, science is so valuable against the Phoenix, and couple that with the fact that Witchrodder could be used as charity, you got global science. This team fight could be getting easily won for them if they take that out.
As you mentioned last game, I'm just drinking your energy drink, by the way. Separate.
You are so greedy. Are just drinking two of them, but that is okay, man.
I just love the taste of my energy drink so much, guys.
Yes, that is it.
We finally got the draft on the screen. That's the applause.
Oh, I see.
Production stepping up their game.
Really incredible production down here. Shout out to the production.
Shout out to production desk. We love you, Charlie.
Yeah, we love you all. 1 minute.
You not so much, Nick.
He could actually come and fight
you. He could put me through a table.
So if Kenwin comes along
this draft,
if the audio cuts, Kenwin is probably dragged off screen and never seen. Oh,
I did warn them that it could happen before game one.
Oh, that's such a good point. I'm just repeating what you're saying.
You're just repeating my warning.
Oh, Skyraf me.
Not seen as much of this here recently.
I still like him. I really do like him quite a bit.
He still does the same thing, right? The same. The nukes out of all of his orifices, all of them.
Yes, yeah, or every single one.
one of the orifices.
Obviously, that target's single target side. It's nice against Witchdot and the Phoenix. It's going to mean Witchdot has to get that BKB if he wants to get his ultimate off for full duration. Phoenix is going to be having difficulties to get his spells out.
And they
can,
of course, use to cancel the sweep if he does go to the offlane.
True. Earthshaker and Skyraf.
It's a decent roaming support duo as well. They can potentially. Fisher, of course, a fantastic ganking spell if you can use it correctly. And it'll be. Who will be playing that? Probably Element. I think I've seen him playing most of the Earthshaker this LAN. And of course, he can, having got to LAN finals, you can use it to block off heroes, even if you don't necessarily get the stun.
I like the fact
that the duration of the stun.
I like the fact that they did ban out the Rubick as well, because Rubick. I talk about this.
Those bans suggest they want to go for a big team fight.
Oh, here we go. Yeah, Spectre. Here we go. This is really nice. Spectre, Phoenix, Witch Doctor. This could be one hell of a fight. Obviously, a game with the potential to go quite late because Spectre, you get that radius up. Eventually, you get a refresh route. And something you've always got to think about when a Spectre's there, the buyback into Horn. Man, you could be winning a team fight.
Yeah, you can pick him and then go and fight straight afterwards, and you can still lose if Spectre has those tools which you've just mentioned. Druids here needing to pick up their two remaining cores. Ichigo, we think, also looking for two cores with Phoenix probably playing a support role. Because that support duo they've picked is pretty good at stopping a Phoenix offlane from being effective. And of course, Phoenix not a hero who can just take it to the jungle for a few levels, needing to get that Sunray up early on. And
Centaur on it. War on it. Nice. Okay, Radiant nice.
It's a decent counter to Spectre. You know, if you're in trouble on the Haunt, you can just use the Centaur to get your team out of dodge. And of course, also serving as an initiator and just a big frontline tank against all this this team fight damage coming out from Ichigo.
Well, Stampede, as you said, is so good. Yeah.
Is this the global strat? Is this happening?
They've done it. They have done it before already. They have done this.
Shout out to Choke Gaming, who were the first global strat memers in UK Dota. It's Nepali Jesus, actually. The rest of them are sort of hangers on to that. But shout out to Nepali Jesus.
Yeah, Nepali Jesus, what a player, what a guy. And we will be going into the fifth ban here for the Radiant. Clockwork was banned out. And I think the Clockwork ban is quite smart because that actually would have been the exact same lineup. Yeah, the exact same lineup Ichigo did against.
Dire team pick.
I want to say Dreads team. It was Dreads. It was actually Dreads. They tried to get. Yeah, sorry, beg your pardon. This is why you're here, man. Able to point this out to me. So, Druids know this is co-ed. They're like, hold on a second.
Yeah, they chose to ban other heroes. They didn't. They also just don't want to deal with the fear Ichigo Medusa. Instead opting to go without a Magnus.
So yeah.
So this last hero, I think his suit was, I think it's probably Tidehunter.
It's the big team fight. Well, Ravage plus the Egg Phoenix comes in, that Supernova, and
lightning everywhere, Death Ward underneath it all.
Yeah, with the Horn.
Do they have enough disables to do it? They do actually. Every hero there has brought a disable for Druids. They are working to combat this sort of amount of channeled spells, which.
On paper, Ichigo's team is obviously disgustingly beautiful, but Druids have got enough here to really try and disrupt them. Obviously, Spectre early is not going to be that great until he gets a couple of items up, but they've got the potential to try and pull out control. I really like the Storm pick. Keep that going. Keep getting the pick. An Anti-Mage.
Well,
nice. Radiant team pick.
I'm not sure what to think of that. This is TI1 now. We have Spectre Anti-Mage in our stage finals.
Man, I like this. I like this a lot. It's always fun to see an Anti-Mage. People go like, oh, he's just farming up gets this.
Anti-Mage is always, he makes the game exciting because if he gets big, he can win fights on his own. Yeah. I mean, Spectre's the same though. We could see this game being a face down between two hard carriers. Mm. And then who wins? Spectre, of course, with Desolate. Can win if it's just a 1v1 fight. But if Idris keeps the supports around, it's not necessarily over, and Centaur really great at keeping people in position with his ultimate.
As we said, the Scarif's going to have like a hard time because everyone else, okay, Earthshaker probably going to be dying quite quickly to the Horn and the Zeus as well.
But if all goes well, Earthshaker's going to be in the middle of the fight anyway.
If Earthshaker's done his spells, he's not going to be that upset about
it. It's Scarif, he likes to stand at the back lines and just keep throwing his flares in. What's that spell called? Arcane Bolt, there we go.
I knew what you were saying. So Ichigo taking their last pick up, Soodle's hero. Well, actually, like we said, Soodle could potentially play the Phoenix, but I think it's the cool. When they did this before, Mute was playing the Phoenix, the Spectre, I believe. Wait, is that right? Actually, no, that was in another game. There was a game where they switched around.
Yeah, I've seen Mute play Carrier a couple of times, and they've let Ichigo go to support. Ichigo, of course, known for his support play recently. The previous iteration of this team that came to Summerland with the Chinese pub stars that Ichigo imported to try and win LAN and failing miserably at that goal.
Heavy words, man.
Bit of flame.
Yeah.
Ichigo played support for that team. He's back in his more traditional carry role. It's how he came to be known in the scene.
Lina.
I'm going to go for the Lina middle. This is one of Ichigo's favourite things. Is it going to be safe lane?
So Soodle will take the Phoenix. Obviously, they have got that. They've got the versatile players. They have got a load of good players. But Druids Esports are ready now. I do like both lineups, so we'll see if this is enough for them to take this. Watson's War on the Zeus. We'll see Spectre picked up by Mute242, also known as Mr. Telephone Man. However, not tagged up as that.
Not that name. We're not going to use that name.
No, we don't use that name. But if you're wondering who I'm talking about, it's the Spectre, so don't worry there. And let us get into this game. So I will quickly run through the Radiant. So on the Radiant, we see Inferno Koi playing that Witch Doctor, Soodle on the Phoenix, Ichigo on the Lina, Watson's Water on the Zeus, and we will have Mute242, Mr. Telephone Man on Spectre. Do you want to go through the diagram?
Yeah, I can. I am just over the mid lane right now where we can see Chocolat on the Storm Spirit Element playing Earthshaker, Iceberg on the Scarif Mage, Laowai on Anti-Mage, and in the bottom lane, we have Nyze on the Centaur. We're a runner. Centaur, nice. I apologize. I just Americaned.
Centaur, potato, tomato, something like that. Let's see what they catch out. So, shout out again, calling. Shout out to sponsors. And Bruno being coming out. They will see how this game goes. So Ichigo have got two games up. This could be
the end of the Emerge Dota 2 Cup.
Druids really have to pull it out, and I want to see if they can do it. Hopefully we can see the games go the distance. Druids, they deserve that much at least. They could hopefully see them.
They were playing late into the night to be here.
Exactly. So they have got the commitment.
Don't doubt the commitment of these teams. They pay or get sponsors to pay for them to be here. And they have to play really long hours because LAN is an unforgiving environment. No sleeping here. I mean, the event's called Insomnia for a reason, guys. Just saying.
So, battle begins. Just taking some damage out onto the Spectre.
That's the first right click blood to Druids there, actually.
Blood has been shed in the river. The river we were on red with the blood of the enemies. And Ichigo will, I don't even know what I'm talking about.
What's going on.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on either, man. And there's going to be Lina playing the support, by the way, and Zeus on the mid lane. So not going to be the Zeus support. Lina support is one which Druids has been doing mainly this tournament, I want to say.
So, Ichigo loves his Lina. Mm. It's like he plays it in pubs all the time.
A great hero.
But, I'm not saying bad thing. But he usually plays it middle. And obviously, I said he was going to. I just saw him pick it and thought, all right, that's middle, because Ichigo's been playing core most of the LAN. They sent him support, though, and I think it's probably the right call looking at the heroes they have.
Just right now, Life Strike Array, onto Nyze. Nyze taking a little bit of damage.
Of course, the problem with Spectre is he does literally nothing in the lane. So, Ichigo can land his big stuns, and then Spectre just stands there and sort of claps. Well done, you got the stun, but there's nothing I can do. I can come and right click ineffectually, if you like.
Well, Soodle at the moment, doesn't have to be careful because obviously Sky is level one, but when that science comes out, he's not going to be able to dive away. With the Earthshaker, get the Fissure off. Okay, it can be a bit awkward because if Sky falls in, but that is like the instant target, single point.
It's one of the best silences in the game. It's a good pick against Phoenix in any circumstance. And that's why I said I thought he'd go support just to avoid this matchup in the offlane, but they choose to take it, and already Soodle having a great time, struggling to get any XP at all. Iceberg zoning him really well.
Indeed. So up top, you can see Element just having a whale of a time pulling away, and Soodle's just drive by on these creeps to disrupt the pool. That's quite nice.
It's not really a surprise, but we're seeing Shrekalaya taking out the advantage in the mid lane in terms of CS. He's getting harassed, of course, which is his strong point in lane, but that terrible animation that Zeus possesses and the weak base damage in comparison to this null stacked regen. Sorry, null.
There is rotations up here. This is a DD.
Any other hero that DD is fantastic, but it's not Zeus.
Zeus,
100 damage. That's nearly what they hit for any. He's going to go down. This is going to be first blood.
And first blood going the way of Druids here. Nice little start for them. And good rotation. Earthshaker just able to come and get a kill. Element just weird the Fissure. Really able to be helping his team out because obviously Zeus grabs the rune. And if that was another rune, maybe a haste, he could have just slipped past them, but double damage.
Haste is the only rune he survives. I think it's one of those carrying sentries still.
That's an incredible illusion bait play.
I mean, it can happen.
Yeah.
They didn't have sentries, so he would have been fine with an invisory. But now Watson's in trouble again. They're hanging around, and he's going to get Fissure. What a great Fissure block. That's another dead Zeus. He gets silent stuff as well. You can't even turn around and try and mute. Well played from Druids. They once again take an early advantage on the kill score.
Similar story to what we see last time. Actually, a lot quicker though. 2 kills, 2 minutes. And this is just going to be Element and Scarif. We talked about the combo. I believe your words was it's pretty damn good. And this is going to be nice to see.
Were those my exact words?
I don't know. I probably put words in your mouth, man. But no, you might not even mention it.
I believe I commented that it was a solid roaming combo as well as one that can control lane. It's a good support combo, what can I say, as the rotation coming elsewhere.
So we've got Watson's Water just being running back with his bottle. Going to see what they can make here. Actually, he is put back a bit now, dying twice in 2 minutes. It's kind of like,
This is a one lane for Shokola. He's only got about one full level because those kills were shared. But Watson's at a deficit now. Also, 7 CS behind. Shokola has a bottle null. He should have boots as well. He's got money for boots already.
Soodle.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
It's a good item, and indeed, it's obviously players. A number. Yeah, also picking up tracks. The go-to boot at the moment, as that was a smoke wasted for Ichigo's team as it wears off.
So wearing off, they will grab the top rune. This time, obviously, Element not able to come in and get
the rune bottom uncontested.
Which is an
Dire has seen what it is, but it is going to actually go to the Radiant. Yeah, Ichigo's going to get there first.
Heading down
see if he guards it for. He won't know. Watson's already got full bottle. He should just take it, I think. Maybe look for. He shouldn't get a kill here. Nice has seen it with the ward. He's seen it pick it up.
Yeah, so they know the threat.
Nice is hanging around.
But then again, with just the spec that you said about what the spec to do, has got
and,
two.
Inferno on his way, of course, another. He actually racked it pretty hard in the early portion of the game.
Not quite level 6 up here. Nice, just stand his ground. He's
got to be careful here, actually. I mean, I know what I said, but I could still die here. But Ichigo misses the stun, though, and
it's a hard one. It is a hard one just to do without. Obviously, he was invisible, did have that going for him, but Nice was just walking around.
Nice was incredibly confident. I mean, his team must have spotted out the rune being taken, but he wasn't scared. Wasn't scared of anything, and just walks it off.
1,001 pings out here. They're like, hey guys, where's their wards? They must have been there. Sorry.
Oh, they've just missed it too.
Yeah, just out there. But there's another sentry, so Ichigo could be placing there. There we go. Gets that out. And so that is going to be your counter ward. So you will get that up soon.
More importantly, that's 50 whole golds.
Whoa. Absolutely incredible.
Insane.
But
for the hard 5 Lina, that's a big deal.
Yeah, true. But obviously you did use 2 sentries. It would have been nicer to you just use the one. But hey, that is quite nice. Get that 50 gold onto him.
Laowai's gone treads before Battle Fury here. We always talk about how, you know, lots of anti-mages choose just to go around these into the Battle Fury, but Laowai confident his farming ability, of course. He's barely missed the last hit with 32 as we approach the 6-minute mark.
I really I really think that this Treads upright first is definitely the right call. You have to really get this Treads into Battle Fury and then...
Unless you go for the stats build, I agree with you. He's not, he's going to take the skills. Maxing mana break first.
Okay, well, seeing as obviously their lineup, you've got three pretty massive mana pool.
Yeah, no, I mean, Anti-Mage will make Susa really sad hero, and also Witch Doctor and Lina, that one. Phoenix, of course, going in the egg sort of decreases the effectiveness of mana break. Though, he, of course, he's really helpful in lane when you're just right clicking on him because you can.
Chocolate happens to bounce it away. And now in the mid lane once more again. This is what happens when there's a Zeus. He gets fished up again.
Oh, the high ground miss.
Oh, no. They still get the kill. It doesn't matter. Now there's going to be the return kill. Iceberg will go down. Haunt was used.
Yep.
And
we talked about what Haunt can do. Honestly, if that high ground miss hadn't happened, I don't think Skyrath had to die there. But he turned around to cast another set of birds and died in the process. But yeah, Mew getting a kill for his first taunt, or getting kill participation, they lost it when somebody else there. And Ichigo are on the board.
Yep, they really are. A one kill up here, and Zeus in the mid lane, it relies solely on the work of his supports to come in and save him.
Yeah, they did make one attempt earlier in the game, but Element support combo just more effective at roaming the incredible long range on both the Silence and Fisher mean that they can just get their ganks a lot more easily. They don't have to be right up close like Lina has to effectively down his stun or Witch Doctor.
With the drive-by, just burnt him down a bit. There's a couple of fire spirits on Lally's to go.
Maui's getting irritated. He's got a ring of health now, so this
still
is...
a lot of damage.
Yeah, it's irritating, but his supports have got regen for him, and he's got ring of health. They're gonna make a go, actually.
Maui,
he's got mana void. Oh, but he used it too early, actually.
Zeus with the
he's
hit!
He's gonna die
to
the tower! No, the salve!
Oh, beautiful.
What a player, Element. He's absolutely just saved his carry's life.
Gorgeous there. If Laoi died, that would have been a disaster just for a attempted gank. So, nicely done.
I mean, it was a misplay from Laoi to use the mana break as early as he did. He only got two rifles on. Look at the mana bar on Tsundra. It's barely down at all. But, yeah, great play from Element to make up for his carry's error and save his life. Well played, sir.
Really well played. And they will grab out the bounty, even topping up that bowl and going to see a rotation.
Meets grabbed an urn on his Spectre. That's his first item.
I really like the urn Spectre.
Yeah, it just encourages you to be active, and that's up here. He sells it.
Up top, we see Soodle get caught out. He does do the flyby, but unfortunately the science came out as he jumped around, and Chocolate was zipping in just to beat him. Soodle, hey, he was going to die for a mid rotation, right?
Yeah. They didn't have all that saw it, so even if Waters called it, he couldn't have known where he was going. Speaking of Master Waters, it's like he's gone back to the base again. He must have taken another pounding in the mid lane. This Storm can just go on him at this point, I think. He's far enough ahead. Watson's... He's only one level behind, but Storm's such a good aggro here at this point of the game. And especially with any support at all, either support, I think, it's a dead Zeus. Zeus is squishy here, and actually no natural escape. Nice has done really well in this off lane, by the way. He's third highest CS. Like, the position that Druid were in last game, where three of the top four farmers are theirs, it's been reversed. Druid's just taking a really commanding lead of the farm, as well as the kill score this game, which they're in a better position than they were. They were narrowly ahead. I think they've got a more tangible advantage. Actually, the Goldcraft is backing me up there. It's nearly 5,000 in their favor.
Stacks being cleared, and obviously Druids are really trying to be keen to get these last
hits. Another comment, Ichigo didn't go in all the jungle this game, did they? So they've been able to stack from minute one. And
Storm's able to clear that out, really helps out his gold. 1,500 gold on turn, already has his.
And of course, they'll have more stacks, because once Anti-Mage finishes Battle Fury, he's going to be able to go through them like the proverbial knife through butter.
Well, we see there's going to be some potential.
Could be a push coming in the bot lane. They've just double stacked the wave.
True.
They use spells to put the camp, so I think they might be trying to get some damage on the tier 1 in bot lane.
That was right. Lina is level 4. So, no, obviously.
No lightning quite yet. And no look at it go either.
But this is to be expected. You're like 10 minutes.
That said, both the Druid supports not really close to level 6, actually. Iceberg will hit it the next creep wave he stands by. He's letting Element get this one, though.
Iceberg has obviously been in 4 kills already. He did give away that one death, but I think that is...
It was an acceptable
died for
trade.
The Zeus.
Yeah.
He had to be there, because as you said, there was the miss, and he had to get that last bolt off. And hey, it works.
Yeah.
So Element has been playing very well this game.
Yeah, Chocolat has excelled himself in this mid lane. He did really well last game, but because things weren't going so great in the other lanes, he fell behind Watson's because he had to leave and go and gank. Mm. This game, he's not been required to. He got that. We had to go. He went and ganked once and picked up a kill on Sudo, but they've ganked for him instead. I mean, it's talking about how the mid game meta has been, the mid lane meta has been shifting in recent years towards this supporting the mid lane instead of mid lane ganking. As the Sentinel comes out, Ichigo in trouble, thinking about dead guys.
Ichigo will be caught here, Stampede, and then naturally that's that lock.
Ichigo sends a cast over the trees.
Spectre wants to go for that Scarf Mage. Obviously, Scarf's got near enough no armor. He pops the horn and goes for it straight away.
He got a last hit, though, so that was value, actually. Nice use of the birds from Skyra.
Well,
yeah, so it's a support trade. And the way Dota works at the minute, it will benefit the teams behind, so that's a good thing for Ichigo. The rubber banding will probably show. Does the recap agree with me? Yeah, they got marginally more XP from that. It's pretty minor, to be honest.
Yeah, XP is actually it's around 3k.
It's closer,
side,
yeah, but it's
5k in gold source druids, which is
druids have done what they like to do and taken the early game advantage. But unlike last game, they have two heroes that can really take them into the late game with it. Spectre, of course, also a very strong late game hero, but other than the spells, they have less backup, and of course, anti-mage doesn't really mind fighting lots of spells.
So Watson's War is going up. Do you think he has to go for a Miser? He's been having a real
He is really behind in terms of gold. His levels aren't too bad, but yeah, he's fifth on the net worth chart. Honestly,
mine.
The Centaur, he's not been doing much, but he's quietly had a fantastic game.
Anti-mage will kill Sudo here, and he's actually got to be not for low enough, but actually Lowy will get that out there. So
we missed it. That's our first kill missed.
First kill missed, and
guys.
That's not forgivable. Well, we've got to be able to take the worst criticism. We are literally the
Sorry,
worst.
Sorry, guys.
So, Elements.
We need OD Pixel back.
Yep. Yeah, he's...
Hashtag comeback OD Pixel.
I'm shaking will be. I'm right here, man. You're bringing me down. And there is Flick Dagger coming up for Element Coach.
Yeah, everything's gone quite well for Triss this year. They've not had anyone have a. Element, of course, with that massive play to save Laowai's life earlier. Possibly a contender for underrated play of the game because it's not actually a big kill. But Mute in trouble.
Oh, Mute. There's that stomp in. Get the Scarabot dropping the cast. Gets bounced around. Ichigo wants to try and throw the stomp.
He does
for it. Unfortunately missed. And now Shocker turns up. Ichigo's
buyback horn. Buyback horn.
Wants to finish. Dies. But could he die for this?
Lightning.
No, they've got no mana left onto the Chocolat. And it looks like
Anti-Mage died in the top lane to the Zuso and Phoenix.
Oh, wow.
We couldn't show you that, I'm afraid. But yeah. Sudal has solo killed the Anti-Mage. That is. Actually, quite
massive.
Big because he's still out.
There's your solo. He's got nowhere to run, but the block.
Creeps blocked him.
There's got to be no time.
He's not
going to
survive. No, he's
gets
still
the burn
dead.
Out. Oh my god, he's still standing.
What?
Second against the final. But Element.
He's going to be fighting.
We'll be okay.
Element cutting a bit of fine. Sudo trying to make the big play, but not quite there.
That dive just too long on the corner. And obviously
it's still worth it, by the way, because Anti-Mage is it's 40 minutes in. The Battle Fury is still a long way away. Actually, he needs another 1400, 1600 gold. Yeah, he's not got it yet. That's a problem for the Anti-Mage. His farm being slowed down, but problematically for Ichigo, this Storm Spirit is getting distressingly large.
Mm.
He looks like he's going to go for the Bloodstone. That's the build at the moment, it turns out. Actually, he's sent the crew to the right now. Is he going to buy it? He can.
Obviously, Bloodstone with Storm Spirit is kind of the farming tool because you just have so much mana. You could just go all over the map and get that out early enough. So some people do still prefer to get that Treads Orchid, but then again, you could argue that it varies on the
See, my problem is that I don't watch enough Dota these days. I'm still sort of running on a meta from a few patches ago.
You are doing more than fine.
I'm a baddie.
Gentlemen. Do not sell yourself short, mate. You have been the guy who stepped
up. Top lane.
We will see another go up here top, and Sudal again gets caught out. Mana Void used out there, and
Laowai recouping his losses from that death. That's big for him.
Yeah. This is nice. So Laowai was going to be getting that back.
The Phoenix has done its job though, because the supports have been so busy supporting the Storm in the lane. Storm goes behind the tower. Watson's Water
is
dead before anything starts. Invernakoi also in trouble. Looks like Chocolate running out of mana. He had a regen rune. He probably could have got a ham there. Where was the ham? But
want to just try and force them into the dives already, don't you? You want to see more.
I love a bit of aggressive data.
Yeah, 4-0-3 up onto Shocker. He's really been playing quite well.
He's had a good game. So, I think all the druids have played well. Laowai may be the only one who we can't wax the record about.
He
discovered Mute.
Spectre, but obviously he's still waiting for
regen's
that regen.
In effect, yeah, he can maybe go. He's got support here, but there's no center ultimate. They used it to get the kill in top lane.
Just wants to be topped back up to full mana. Carrier delivering out that Bloodstone. That's going to be the 16.
It's 15 minutes.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Well, it still had 15. You just don't look at the seconds. That's good enough, man. And let us...
It's the pub strat, isn't it? And it's like when you get your Battle Fury at 40 minutes and 50 seconds, you're like, oh, yeah, it's 40-minute Battle Fury, guys. I'm literally burning. Speaking of 40-minute Battle Furies, it looks like Laowai is most of his way towards it now. The Courier's going to Secret Shop to get the Perseverance, and once he clears some jungle camps, I don't know where he's going, on an adventure. But he's most of the way towards that Battle Fury being finished. Perseverance done.
So, you talked about Druid having the opposite of Ichigo last time. They had three of their net worths at the top, and now this is all potential.
That was nearly a thing, guys. Which we're not allowed to talk about.
And Laowai is going to be farming up here, building that Battle Fury up, and potential for him to just get that up quite quick now. But everyone's kind of farming their own thing.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Vertigo moves forward, shows himself, throws the casting, unfortunately animated evasion to slip away. Quite awkward for them to go, obviously Ichigo doesn't have any
ulti. They threatened a TP too and they had to cancel because Ichigo was standing on it with the stun. Haunt from Spectre going in.
Down bot, there could be a play, they used the Zeus ult as well, and these people are pretty low. And now there's just Stampede running away, there's the Fissure which connects on two of them. Soodle seals the burden, gets the Supernova, unfortunately
just run away.
Zoning.
Zoning Supernova, that's fine.
And no way to pulled out there, a little bit of all chat.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
About some, and they do throw out their ults. See what they
everyone's favourite smiley face.
And let me just check. Yeah, he did deny his tranquils there. That's what the centaur was talking about. He did drop him on the floor, and I was wondering what the play was there. He had dropped it down onto the tower, and obviously Haunting gets the deny off on the
tranquils. He was farming creeps.
So yeah,
okay, that explains the haunt. So I was like, why is he haunting when he could TP?
I'm obviously being extremely slow today.
We've both been bad there, actually, so it's fine. Well played, Mute. We take it back.
Yeah. So obviously Haunting, Garrett off, because I got confused with saying where they wanted to go. Dropping tranquils underneath tier one
is risky. That was a risky play. I was saying nice play.
But then again,
well,
it's only
look what it's done to his net worth too. He used to be third, but because his tranquils are dead, he's gone to fourth. Terrible.
It's kind of funny, but let's face it.
There's the Battle Fury pits up Franti Major, 18 minutes. So it's a bit slow, but he did get treads first. He will now probably head towards. We've seen him go Vlad as his
Radiant
next item because we say that Druids like to fight and. Manta style does actually delay anti-mages joining the fun.
Around him, going to get burned up, goes to Blink. Ray actually doesn't get it, actually was hit by the rest of the dive. But Center Ult just able to back them out. So Ichigo and Co. still holding this tower before it's being picked up. And circles are being drawn on the map. So.
Excellent. The analysis.
I know, yeah. Quality, mate. Say what I say, that's my casting. And Chocolate will now be just pushing down these. Creeps in the mid lane, let's see what they can grab out here. Go for this tier one, let's see if
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Come back, but then again, that chocolate's very hard to do anything against him. And Walton's Water did go the minus. I don't know if you did mention it, and apologies if you did, but Walton's Water has the minus.
I did
not
mention that. Good luck.
I try my best. 2,800 gold up onto the Spectre at the moment, and there's now a rune picked up by Storm Spirit. Another purchase now here. And
yep, there
he's
replaced his tranquil boost.
Has replaced
well
his tranquil.
It's very important.
Gets him back out to it. Nice is now got his boots. Will he make the same mistake twice? I very much doubt it. He's got to be having this.
That's the tool now. They know that you have a thing with denying tranquil boots. So
what, bait him in?
Yeah, it's just array. Put it on the floor and just hide who your heroes behind.
Oh no, I've dropped my shoes in the mid lane. There's going to be the Laguna Blade. And that is the kill. There's the Supernova behind. And I said about Storm being hard to catch, but they proved me wrong and just catch him out. The Laguna Blade was utilized. And it's one of those things.
They got some kill streak going for that as well. He was dominating. So that's a fair amount of gold who actually got lost it. Watson's did, so he's on the recovery road. Good for him. Yield's had to finished on the.
That would be quite
he's got
nice.
A haste
yeah,
through. He's got
gonna be the horn. He wants to come out, and there is gotta be use there, but down bot there is another rest of the kill. They are looking elsewhere. The animation nearly died in the exchange, but now Soodle getting caught out by the vortex. Chocolate getting in trouble. Got to be spurred it up a little bit, but there is a magic tournament. It's not going to be enough node dive there, and it looks like the rest of them are going to be heading away. Element still stand, does have the extra slam available, but are you going into this?
That's a 2-for-1 trade for Ichigo. They did lose Mute, though, who is the most important hero for them to farm, only for the the tranquil, the newly tranquil booted Centaur and the hard 5 Skywrath Mage.
So, down.
Could be another clash here in the woods that this ward, this indistinct thing, which I'm not allowed to say, but Druids have lots of information.
Brilliant recovery Kenwyn. Absolutely phenomenal.
Multiplay, give soundproof booths, please.
Oh, man. Hey, but we're doing what we can. So, 21 minutes of the game. Net worth. Centaur has taken a dramatic drop, but still not that much between him and the Zeus. And see if they can come now. Nice money of order. Spectre, checking out his gold. He's working towards his items there, Kenwyn.
Yeah, he's pretty good for the Radiance. I mean, there's no other reason to be holding 3,500 gold in your inventory. It's not the fastest Radiance Meats ever got, but he did stop for the urn and the treads beforehand, and he has died 2 times as well. Fortified. All these things will slow any man down. So, mid tower's going to go here, I think, for free. Shockwave's just going to pick that up.
And Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Making sure they keep the stats flowing their way.
Is that the first tower? No, they did lose top earlier. Second tower. Yeah, Druids will continue to grow their gold advantage.
There we go.
In comes Shakoa. Nice. Fisher cutting them off. Two sketches ulti off from the center ult to follow. In comes the Sunray.
Centaur blinks against the Soul of Scarves. Our Woods drop as well. One Swan still running. There is no stone available, but then Spectre spooks in from the back lines, gets that off, and wants to try and finish off the center. There is an air charge available, but Storm Spirit's going to be trying to finish them off. Obviously,
he's saving his
as well. And there is they get the urn. Shows the value of the kill. It's a double.
Oh, baby. A double.
Baby, a double.
Let's check that. So that's it's a 2-for-2.
Yeah,
supports. It's a narrow win. Oh no, it's a support and offlaner.
It's literally a support and an offlaner.
it's a really close trade. And of course, if you trade even when you're behind, you're probably getting more out of it.
The Spectre did get those kills, which really does help him out. 4,600 Radiance.
Radiance is nearly done. And that, of course, greatly increases his ability to contribute to the rest of the map.
Two Blink Initiators.
They have got them.
Yeah, you've got.
I've not seen Elements is yet to get that you know, Colossal Blink Echo. He did get the one on Zoodle in top lane.
True. And this is going to get harder when you have the Haunt Radiants coming out. You're like, guys, we can't go in. We can try and pop Stampede to run in or run back and then try and come in afterwards.
Radiance, of course, the other thing the Radiance does is cut through the Blink Daggers. And when you have Haunt, you can be anywhere on the map. Let the fun begin. Where was that?
That was down bot. He was just sipping, farm up creeps, kill the tree line so he's not going to get surprised. And I think that's all.
Yeah, okay.
It's fine. It's good to be keen.
Keno.
Yeah. And this tower is on 138 HP.
They've got no glyph.
Chocolate will just be doing what
they've got the two supports. They've got two superior supports in the wings, too. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Go throwing stuns on creeps. That's fine.
Going for this.
The Vlad's finished off for Laowai. He usually goes Manta now, and he's already got the Asher. Some good farm coming out now. Anti-Mage, of course, his farm accelerates ridiculously when he finishes that Battle Fury as the Radiance is finished. I mean, for comparison, we've nearly got effectively two big items done for one on Heat. But he's leaving it inactive for now, so maybe hoping that they won't notice. So we've said the names probably ruined that.
Well, try to ruin any surprise ever seen.
It doesn't really matter. They didn't say they could hear us. They just said they could hear all the sound effects on the map.
So there was something going on here, but then it was cancelled. So we'll look away from that. But Infernokoi walking around through the jungle, able to farm up. Obviously, cast bean can be used really nicely to just get there.
You check the area.
Yeah.
So big stack going the way of the Druids. Laowai is in danger of dying, but he'll be fine in the end. The Vlad's, of course, letting him sustain a bit better.
BKB out to Storm Spirit.
We haven't really talked about this, but BKB is a really big item in this game. It stops basically three of the heroes and Ichigo doing their job.
And obviously, because there's a support Lina, we're not going to be seeing the Aghanim's out quickly because...
And he's stopping off.
Whereas the ulti, will realise the smoke is there, thanks to it. They're like, okay, it's
They still managed to catch Inferno.
It's
really good play from Druids. I mean, they would have wanted more from that smoke ideally, but once they realised the jig is up, they still managed to go and get a pick from it. So, well played from them.
They peeked behind the curtain and they were still able to find someone. And this is going to be a potential bit of farm now. Anime just in the jungle. I don't know. I feel scared. I feel that Ichigo's team fight, they've thrown out this, and I've got to say, nice for what's for, just utilising that Thunder God's Wrath. He's like, not sure where they are, guys, they might have done a smoke, let's quickly just check it out. Okay, yep, they have, yep, we saw Animage still in the fight, but unfortunately, Inferno, obviously it's a Witch Doctor, he's walking around with probably
600 hit points and 2 armour. Yeah, you're not going to survive, are you?
He's like, oh dang, I'm in the wrong neighbourhood at the moment.
Yeah, he's his first death, and given that his team
survived, oh, what I missed.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Impressive. Well yeah. done, Inferno. I mean, I know you hate to praise him, but
No, he's doing good. He's playing well, and I've got to give credit where credit's due. And there's now a. Dramatic pausing, mate. I was trying to build fanfare.
Trying to figure out what the item's called. We're playing Hon, right? Tonight.
No, yeah.
There's your dump. Oh, dearie me. Blown up. Just wrong place, wrong time.
Literally just turned up to this lady. He's like, guys.
An instant reaction from Element. No messing up. Element, even not messing around. Just seeing the TP, in he goes, the big dunks.
He's like, yeah, like some people I find hold these big ults too much, and they're like, okay, guys, we want to just try and get.
It is a big kill.
Just want to get value. Yeah.
They'll probably send the anti-mage back for a BKB as well at some point because they've already gone in Storm, and then. Once they have BKB, they only need to worry about standing in a Hakanim's Wish Doctor on Z, which worked for a while, or getting killed. Still realizes there's more heroes there and goes home.
He zips about, zips in, zips out, and he's
kind of if you want to check something,
you have
noticed.
Things are happening.
Things are happening.
Like in Dota 2, there's always something happening.
They've actually had to give
and
up.
And another thing going on there.
Oh, they sent more heroes in there. Yeah.
So, we will see a 4 staff coming out onto a Witch Doctor shortly. Susan the Crow walking around. Here's the official, they've been baited, and this is huge! The Zeus ult has been thrown out. Scarfall is there. Witch Doctor, is still channeling back at the sidelines. 2 of them are dead. There's your Phoenix Supernova. And now Storm Spirit wants the official, wants more. 4 staffs out, and then able to get away. And Animage is incredibly low as well in this fight. Did manage to finish up that lead. There's the Urn Charge onto him, so he's on 50 on HP.
Element regrets his decision instantaneously.
Gets the fish off. Yeah. Guys, this fight, it looks like
it's a big win for Ichigo. That's 3-1. And the gold chain swinging. Oh, look at that XP change. Thank you, Everbanding. Oh, boy. That's 5,000 XP from one fight.
That's tasty, man. That is like Druids. I thought they played that near enough perfectly. They came out.
They executed the backstab.
Yeah, and it was quite.
They've lost that gem as well.
Yeah. So, Soodle sitting back at the back line. I really like this pick up. Obviously, we've seen all the Phoenixes. I think all the Phoenixes bar one by a Yule's out, right?
Yeah.
You can swoop in.
It's a good item, man.
Yes. I mean, obviously, the value of a Yule's cannot be understated full stop, but then coupled up with the synergy from Phoenix, you can dive in. Yule's one of them out, get that supernova channel in, and that just buys guaranteed time. But you're not getting the auto attack.
One less auto attack coming in.
Exactly. But dives by it. Another little try-by.
Just irritating.
5 seconds.
Manta finished on Laowei. He's overtaken Stilma as the most farmed hero on the map. It's interesting who he goes for next. I think it could be a BKB. That fight demonstrated what all that magic can do if they do manage to chain their spells properly.
Dire's middle tower has got the chair under attack. There. I wanted to do some counter order the Spectre with the Radiance. Probably going to go for that Scatty next. Like, the Scatty value on a Spectre can be huge. And really going to help that. Storm Spirit will kill the Roshan, as we saw. They were going for it. And this time, they don't have to worry about trying to go for any baits. They will just go in and take it.
Yep. It was still not on full HP from their last attempt, so it was a pretty quick one. They sent the whole team, and Anti-Mage had a double damage room. So it was a really quick pressure.
I'm hearing that. So. Lina does have the degree rate up. Still no Yules, but shortly out. What do you think about these items after the Yules? Do you think they should go for a blink? Because obviously they are still a support, so they have to really rely on just near enough the kills alone. Could do
Radiance
some jungling.
As you point out, if they all get BKBs, Lina becomes a pretty useless hero, unfortunately. Yules. It is possible to get the BKB on while you drop from Yules, so even if you perfectly chain the stun combo, you're not guaranteed to get one. So maybe Aghanim's is the play, though of course blinks there, and you never have too many blinks as they yield up the storm here. He's going to deploy.
Unfortunately, yeah. It's always a hard catch for a storm, but he's still standing around. Oh, standing pretty well forward. He's not here, just again, seeing if he can bait anything out, but really
dear.
Getting the farm up in the lane. And
the smiley face.
The cheeky chappy smiley face.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
So. Sudo. Do you want to see him get that Sheevan now? Like, the plate mail's on him, and obviously
the,
he could just...
Has he got the money?
No, it doesn't have as it obviously built it as next item, but yeah.
Yeah, it's a good item, it disrupts team fights. Of course, it's if Santor holds the ult, but Santor shouldn't have to hold the ult with the Radiance. They should have to use it to initiate. Yeah, I think it's a good item. It can... there are not many of the heroes are kiteable. It tanks him up, it provides the neck armor debuff, it still does its work, it's just some of its utility is decreased by Druid's team comp. It's not like they have strength carries who are going to be incredibly sad by the movement speed debuff.
Well, let's see what they can find out now. Centaur has got its blink on him, as we were talking about earlier. That blink catch can do so much, and I'll let's quickly check in overall and see if we've missed anything. So
yeah, Anti-Mage is going to go for that BKB, it looks like he's got the Ogre Club already.
It's gonna be nice. I feel like Element and Nyze are gonna be core to winning this next fight for Druids.
Yep.
And obviously this is a 2-0 currently to Itchy. Go.
I mean, we should mention there's this big goal lead for Druids, but I'd say like what about 5,000 of that is actually tower gold. It's not as large as it appears. There is a way back into this
there's
game.
There's still gold to be unlocked.
Yes.
And it feels like Ichigo knew they weren't gonna be able to do as much in that regard because of the
heroes. Their problem is just how far ahead the Anti-Mage is over their Spectre, because he's got 6,000 more gold. There's 2 BKBs come out from Druids. I don't think they'll be scared of the fights anymore. They have to jump the Spectre, and then the rest of that team is going to look quite sad. Save one disable, of course, for the look at it go from the Witch Doctor.
Yeah, and we will see if they go back.
They're going to send Laoi on the front lines to hit the tower. Standing in the back. And Ichigo realize they can't fight and do their favorite tactic of hiding in the base.
They're sitting at the high ground.
Yeah.
Where they feel most comfortable, most at home, and this tier 2 is going to be on top.
They're going to clear the map out.
Yeah, clear all tier 2s, then you can think about your high ground seed. Still got that Aegis. 3,300 gold on turn.
They have got a team that are capable of dying. I mean, with the BKB and the Aegis, this is the time, surely. How long have they got left on that Aegis? They have got about 3 minutes left to go. So they are just going to walk up on the high ground. And in goes Storm Spirit. He grabs Ichigo with the pull. With the fight, a rocks all over the place. Supernova comes in deep. They want some water on it. Doesn't do anything.
Commits, gets the Supernova egg down, and Chocolate is running back. Laoi did pop his 10 second BKB flat.
He did.
And they get the kill.
Oh, they're going to. Oh, Mute's, Mute's gone ham on the chase, but he's overextended. Oh, and it's blown up by the man. And that's a pretty big win. They've got two of the cores down, and they still have the Aegis even. They didn't even have to expend that on Shakalar, so they should surely just go for the high ground here. This is their opportunity. They're waiting for the creep wave.
Well, Cabals have been sundered, and this is going to be one hell of a fight. So
there's not even a walk in this game.
No, he did say the line there still. Bottom tower but is I'm under just saying,
now. Oh, yeah, Anti-Mage. It's the same voice actor.
They
sound
the same.
Oh, they
do sound the voice.
Oh, my bad.
Ah, see, now you've embarrassed yourself there, Kevin. Where's the professional cast?
What do you mean? Now you've embarrassed yourself.
Oh, yeah, actually,
like,
good point. Soon there was a tower that's now being focused on. Now allowing
Ichigo going for the sneaky lightning.
Oh,
it's a pity he has that spell that makes him take no magic damage.
Yeah.
Ichigo's going to die for it, but that's a decent stall, and he's dropped to... The Anti-Mage and Alcor just can't stand high ground because he might die to lightning bolts.
Literally the Anti-Mage, and there is going to be 28.
They're
going to
hold this.
Oh, there's a zip in. This time he was catched out. Fedekoi was catched out, just had this delivered, and he goes to war.
Oh, his Aegis has expired.
There's the Scarab Old Drop, he's lost the Fissure as well. All of these people are just running away now. They've got their objective, they got the tier 3, they got some kills, and they forced a buyout, so they are going to just run out of here.
Yeah.
There's going to be a TV away from
him. Aegis actually expired as he zipped in.
Yeah.
I think his strings are clenched a little bit as he saw it drop. From his inventory.
Nice. Obviously, you would be like, okay, I'll save a BKB before they come back out. Let's score back into the game to get this chocolate. Very,
cooldown.
Very low, unfortunately. Yeah, they're not able to get the full combo. And that's a buyback into the ultimate, which
for
got nothing. Druids have really.
On the bright side, his Midas is off cooldown, so it was a value buyback because now he can just go and use his Midas. Look, here we go.
You are an optimist. I like that. So we are.
He's not even used his Midas. I mean.
But let's just see.
Okay, I'm livid.
you are livid a bit, but we'll try to look into it. So, Radiance.
He's used it now. Just so you guys know.
Oh, nice.
I'm not a big
thanks
idiot.
Thanks to QB updated, man. And BKB got to be purchased up onto Element at some point here. Now, Check another buybacks. Witch Doctor, four back. So did the Zeus. Oh, and there is Chocolate just zipping in to get the last hits.
Obviously. Of course, that's the most important thing. Yeah, the only buybacks active for the Radiant are Spectres.
Oh, Shaker, they want to try and fight play. Unfortunately, the stun's not there, and now's another Stampede. Doodle does use the Supernova, and Stormtrooper's just thinking, okay, I'll back away. The Eyes on the back lines just uses that beacon. He gets a three-man Storm, on a two-man, sorry, and they are going to just dive. Ichigo is going to be going down already, and that one's War Walks into the Skyfall. He'll dive the Witch Doctor, he will be
look at it go!
Nice. Inferno Koi able to get something back in the exchange. Chocolate does have a little bit of mana to jump down here, and nice play from the element there to get the Fisher off and be able to back him out. So that is a 2-for-3 exchange.
Yeah, it's a narrow win for Druids. They got more high value heroes. But, well, it's pretty even actually. Let's look at what the recap says. Actually, Ichigo got more gold and more experience out of that. So thanks, Rubber Banding. They'll be happy with that, I suppose. Can we just comment on Element's play this game? He's had a cracking game on his Shaker. He's 2-1-11. Just one death in 37 minutes of play. All power to the guy playing a hero that is designed to go into fights and perhaps get, you know, one of the first to be have his head caved in. He's done really well.
Laoi has been just farmed up really well, doing like the anime, doing them proud and able to get this next time up there. I think he had to get that BKB when he did, which is really nice. And they are making that stuff of it. Obviously, when the BKBs come out, there is a issue of, okay, if we don't take this, we're going to be getting these down to 5 seconds and into a point where you can't be fine into this much lockdown.
Yeah.
That'd be difficult.
Meets specking for Split Push. It looks like he picks up the Manta style over the heart is the next item. I think that has to be the play, doesn't it? The way this game's going, they have to do the classic Ichigo style of just trying to stall the game out, get some towers when they can, slowly rebuild their position, because right now they are very, very behind the Storm Spirit and the Anti-Mage, both huge. We saw in that last fight, though, without its mana, when it's quite low, Storm really struggles in 1v1 fights against the Spectres. Even now, even you know, with a 7,000 gold lead, there's the natural kit of that hero allowing him to trade even, but the Anti-Mage, I think, is still too much. He's just picked up a heart as well. He'll probably go for the... I don't think he's got room for the Butterfly. He's got to sell the Vlads and pick up a...
Yeah, someone else seems to be holding advance for him.
A better item in that slot.
Yeah, he has got that heart as his thing.
Got another BKB coming out for Druids, by the way. Just finished on the Earthshaker.
Yeah, the Storm.
Storm zips.
So there, camp.
There's no one there,
babe. No, be excited, because there's a little bit of last hits. Yeah.
I love last hits, man. That's exciting.
I mean, it is exciting.
The little noise it plays.
That gold noise is one of the most satisfying to hear into a game of Dota 2.
Looks like Druids are going to wait for the next Roche spawn before doing anything. Mm-hmm. Little do they know that it's quite soon.
Yeah. So nicely whispered. And Infernicoid is going to be 1,800 gold. Maybe just has to get BKB over there, the Agonins out, or do you think that maybe they have to get that potential team fight shot?
I think if they can keep Meat alive, he can probably do the damage. He's got lots of Radiant stacking now, it's all going to go quite nicely for him. But it's a hard one, isn't it? They've got to make that choice.
Big man's going to be coming up shortly, and that is going to be nice farming up the jungle. So Element and Co. just farming around, and it has been spotted out. So do you think that Radiant can do anything if they want to go for this? Seed will just throw out the last of his fire spirits, just getting that cooldown taken.
I don't think so, unfortunately. What have they got? What have they got for them right now?
The Haunt Zeus hasn't
because Spectres chose to pick up the Manta. He didn't get a fight item. He didn't get a heart or a butterfly, so they'll let him stay in the fight longer. So, I mean, it's great for this. He's, you know, he can defend the base without putting himself in any danger, as he's doing in the top lane right now. But he can't walk into the middle of the team and not die. So that's a really easy Aegis. Once again, they didn't have an option. I don't think they had a choice. They have to fight under their tier threes on the high ground, and pray they can execute.
So we talked about the fact that Animage has been so high on the net worth, but look at how big this Storm Spirit is as well. He's now got a side with that Shiva's Guard. This is going to be really hard to take down. You've got two lives on the Storm, and then he's got a Bloodstone with 18 charges. This guy is just going to keep coming back, and you just cannot get rid of him. Like a bad spell, he's going to be all over.
He's those BTs as well, and then he can wrap up and fight some stealth gaming going on here. And look at these drawings on the map. These are works of art.
really some tactical.
It looks like Druid wants a group. I think that was what that meant. They're gonna make the push.
Here I am.
Zipping it up onto the high ground, getting that vision with the remnants.
So he does just hit a little bit of lightning, just see if they see.
And now he's just gonna go on the tower. Can they stop him? They're gonna use the sunlight. That's a good thing. Percentage damage is always helpful.
Fast bounce between them. Just clears out the illusions. Obviously, nice, just stops the guaranteed damage.
He did half damage that tower with that one use of Manta. 20 seconds, he can do it
Bear
again.
Bear in mind, he has got a heart. So, a heart is one of those items you just think for siege. You go in and you'll just be like, okay, whatever, I'll back out soon. It just does a drive by with the fire. It can get the burn going, and now there's going to be a tower going out here. Three will die. I expect to just try to get forward, but unfortunately,
they've dropped him to half HP. That's one bounce. Oh, what?
Well, they actually
what?
Does. I thought for a second that they were going to come close together and it was going to be a full. Obviously, not a win. Important cast, but just funny to see anyway.
That spell always brings amusement. But they've got part one instant sentry ward coming down here, so they've still got vision of invis stuff in case they want for anything cheeky.
Now, this could be alright coming down. They could just be focusing down that range. He has much control. See the bird's nice bird. Oh, chocolate. There's just yules on yules. Everyone's up in the air. Jump around. Will they be able to get anything? There's the Zusol and the.
Agon and Zusol actually doing work. Chocolate pretty low. He has to zip.
BKB's popped, you will get the stun off and
Sunray being used to heal up the Spectre so he can keep the chase going.
It's got that talisman of evasion, coupled with the Manta.
Yeah, he's gonna get a butterfly now, it looks like. Or maybe is he gonna go Sands for the race car?
There is gonna be an animation being cast again. Fair bit, but punch mana and then there's another cast here and then Burb from Phoenix. Quite nice to stop this. Well, not stop but slow down the push. Not going onto that range.
That is lag, we got that too, I think.
Yeah. We are going back into this game, so that was only a quite
Meek says they've almost won, and I believe him. He's a very trustworthy young gentleman.
You is the man with confidence, the man with the plan. He did actually type one as in the number rather than one, though, so I am going to call that
out. I didn't even flame him for it. That was very restrained.
He did have a hard night last night.
Oh, he went hard. He did. Shout out to Blackout Hearthstone.
Oh, he is a mess. And there were some plants out there for the Blackout. Anyway, Laowei, go for this Melee Rats there. It's going to be a lot of rain thrown out. Laguna Bay barely scratched onto Hanny and Soodle goes down. And there's going to be a void. But there's Echo Slam from Element. Catching onto him with Scars. Oh, they gain more kills. Soodle's
now not got a buyback. He's not got a buyback. And there's the game.
GG, well played. Well played, Druid. You're back in.
2-1 the score now in this series. We are going to a game 3.
This is really nice, man. Well played indeed, Druids. They showed they could get it off. They had the lead for most of the game there, and they really were quite.
They did what they love to do. They took an early advantage and they just steamrolled all the way to victory. Ichigo had their moments, but unfortunately, Spectre just couldn't keep up with the farm of his opponent cores. Good map control from Druids to allow that. The teams are going to quickly take a comfort break, and I think we are
going to take a quick break. So
then we will be back in roughly 10 minutes with game 3 of the Emerge Dota 2 Cup Finals.
Don't go anywhere.
And here is the draft.
Here we go, guys.
And Lion is naturally me. I don't look like that. I mean, it's close. I'm pretty ugly. But anyway, we've had the first bans, a change in our first bans the first time this series. Storm is gone after being a very influential hero in both games we've played so far. But Lion getting through, therefore, his first Radiant pick for Druids. Pick. He'll play the hard support. Witch Doctor we've already seen several times. We've also seen Phoenix already. I'm getting a strange sense of deja vu, weren't it? Goes first two picks last game, Witch Doctor and Phoenix. Rust?
Yeah. So, Witch Doctor, Phoenix coming back again. Didn't work from last game.
No,
but
it didn't.
This could be the.
Those weren't the pieces of the puzzle that failed for them. No. They lacked the cores, really struggled. The damage dealing cores. Phoenix was pretty disruptive. Remaining. Actually, solo killed Laowei, which on the anti mage, which is big. And we know they can also switch the roles up and have Mute player as a support hero, depending on how the rest of this draft goes for them.
Very first.
As we see, another hero we saw last game returning to the fray, Centaur Warrunner. Another hero that it's just good, isn't it? Solid in lane, if you don't drop your Tranquil Boots especially.
Cool, that's nice there, dropping his Tranquil Boots, getting the 9 up.
Shout out to Mute for killing them, excellent. Also, of course, has great teamfight presence, and he's just irritating. He's hard to kill. Good hero.
As
we head to the bans, they're going to get rid of the Mute Enigma.
One of the best. Yeah, and Radiant we'll see the science ban. Being banned
again,
now.
Of course, Phoenix, a vital ban again when you've picked them. Phoenix.
So Druids Esports will ban out every game they have banned out of a juicer. Ichigo's team, I think they'd want to take it if they can. You obviously don't want to take it as a first or second, but just one of those things now. Let us quickly go into that next ban now. So Ichigo's team and the Druids Esports, they've had 10 seconds great remaining. Runs here.
Yes, Druids of course had the struggles. They were put down, they had to win a best, they were in the risky best one against Joe Gaming in the lower bracket, but they came through and they 2-0'd Rich Gang, who many would have called favourites coming into this LAN, including myself because I seeded them first. Moron. But they were put firmly in the bin by Druids in two very quick, very brutal victories. And then they engaged in a very close best of three series with Divine Esports, Dread Knights mixed team at this LAN.
10 seconds remaining.
The fraudsters, of course.
Here he is.
Radiant team. Awesome.
I mean, I'm impressed you've made it three games without seeing him. So two games without seeing him. Mm. Everyone's favourite little goblin swordsman.
Goblin's a little bit harsh, but yeah, he's...
He's quite little and he's quite yellow, I mean.
Yeah, okay, fair play.
Is that racist?
No, it's
not. Whoops.
I think it might be now you mentioned it, but let's go Radiant pick. Let's look into this next one. Druids Esports. Seeing what they can take up now against them.
Yeah, well, Juggernaut is a carry who comes online very quickly in this game, of course. He's just hitting six and he can get solo kills.
So currently they've got their hero for Nyze. Lion, obviously one of their supports, could be given to either Element or...
I think it's an Iceberg hero, usually.
Yeah, Iceberg.
We'll see, of course. Depends what they get for Element. Element, of course, coming off a big game. I think he's got my MVP star for last game, just for saving Laowai's life at the start. The big clutch salve. And he's from the UK, guys, just in case.
Yeah, so there is, well, obviously, UK team in the finals. Mm. You got Ichigo there. And Druids, they do have a... whereabouts are they all from? Do you know?
Oh, they're from a mix of countries. Laowai is Swedish.
Swedish, yeah.
There is, one of them is from Austria. Mm. I think two Swedes, there's an Austrian, a Dane, and a Brit as well, I think. I'm not going to go out on a limb and assign them all nationalities because I'll probably make a mess.
No, that's fine. Don't do that much, but it's nice to get that back. But Ichigo's team, all from the UK, so let's see if they can do this through. And as we talked about already, there is some LAN winners there, Infernokoi and Mute 242.
I think Mute's on more than one LAN as well, thanks to his tenure with The Rock. Mm.
And Clockwork now being picked up here, we'll see it's
Radiant take that team pick.
Hopefully he's able to go ham, get these positions in, and kind of disrupt their team.
We're going to see the position for Phoenix then, which we talked about before last game. Mute is very competent at the hero, so...
Mm-hmm. And
hopefully see him go ham.
The Phoenix, when we saw it come out, he was able to just get some farm, get the Midas out, eventually able to burn down creeps wherever he likes, come in. And it's just... you need to make the right calls when you go in for these supernovas.
Yeah.
I don't think it was so much that Seal didn't have the... It was more that...
They were already... The team was at a deficient reserve time. They were not having a good game.
But it happens. But they, at least they had the game to drop. So
yep.
This is the game for them to bounce back in. 2-1.
Secure the series. Of course, the winner of this match will take home a cool £2,000. Courtesy of... Multiplayer Emerge, Dota 2, what a cup. And the loser will take £850. Or maybe it's just £800. Dire not the Cancer Lancer. Why's that happened?
Phantom Lancer being picked up now here.
Druids have played this hero before at LAN. They actually used it against Rich Gang, I think. Maybe that was against Divine.
10 seconds remaining.
Not sure. Is that Divine with an E or Divine with an I?
D-E-Vine. Sorry.
That's no problem. Yeah, because I was going to say, when we saw Divine play Druids, they did ban out Phantom Lancer, I believe, reserve every time. Game. So.
Yeah. Oh, obviously, the hero recently got getting reworked with the new... No longer has he got a Doppelwalk, he's got Doppelganger instead. And he
Radiant
has the,
team
the new Rush thing. Yeah. Instead of his
definitely is a thing.
Yeah, I don't know what's it actually called. It's
I believe it's just called
Phantom Rush, which is what you think it'd be called. Okay.
So you were right by saying Rush, but Phantom Lancer is a great hero. I think he's maybe a little bit underutilized. You see.
Oh, he's got to work his way back in. Everyone's so happy with the Troll Warlord, etc. At the moment. And so Ichigo have one more quarter pick, probably a mid laner, and Druids. also have a quarter pick, probably a mid laner.
There is that leader available if
Oh, they still have Ban, and they're going to use it on Quap.
We need a pain.
And they take the Magnus.
Magnus Juggernaut. This is going to be very nice. Very, very nice indeed. So, being able to see if they get those clutch RPs, but even without landing, obviously ridiculous, you know, 5-man RPs, not necessarily.
Empower
needed.
Is such a useful spell to have on your team, especially when you have a melee carry like Juggernaut, who's already he's going to have a crit naturally.
They're going to be able to come on quite early. Phantom Lancer, until he gets a couple of items, he doesn't bring that much to it. Just obviously a couple of lances. You can try and just double get yourself away. Just try and, you know.
He's very hard to kill now, especially Phantom Rush, if you can attack to a neutral creep or something and just 5 seconds silly remaining. Magic dashing away.
And the last bit.
Druids have got 50 seconds to it. Oh, we're gonna see a random, the BM random.
I'm sure they'll be looking into it now. They are huddled around, trying to discuss this last pick. So with 7 seconds left on the clock now, they will go for the Hour Devourer.
Well, that's a decent pick against Magnus, of course, because Magnus, not a high-end hero early in the game, can't actually make put it to the point where he can't use Shockwave, which is a really sad situation to be in as a middle laner. But Intrigo's going to take the Magnus. We are going to see Mute on Phoenix. Watson's is going to play the carry hero this game, it looks like.
So, we'll be getting into this game very shortly. I'm Russ, joining me Kenwin. We have made it so far without dying, so this
is good. We haven't fallen asleep on the keyboard. It's progress.
Yeah. It's going well. You having fun?
I'm having a great time, mate.
Good, yeah. Obviously, Kenwin is not actually a caster. You are here to do some admining.
Yeah, but unfortunately...
They realised you weren't very good at that. So
they put me something else. No. All the other casters have run away, or weren't awake at 10 a.m. when we had to start sound checking.
10 seconds remaining.
I'm pretty close to that.
Yeah, Ross sort of rocked up 20 minutes beforehand.
Exactly. 20 minutes is comfortable. That's what I like to see.
Comfortable, so much time. He was only just after Ichiko's team.
Well, I'm surprised to see the teams up here on time. Actually, that's a little bit of disrespect there.
That was a flame.
Maybe more to Mute, because Mute was...
Mute went hard. Once again, shout out to Blackout. And Cook, actually.
A shout out to Joe Show, who unfortunately is meant to be the co-caster here, but he is unwell, and he has missed the whole land. So, Joe Show, get well soon, buddy. Weird. Don't do that. Anyway, so now going through the teams. For Druids, we will see Nyze playing that Centaur again in the offlane Iceberg. Onto the Lion, Element playing Earthshaker. And let us go through and see Laue playing that Phantom Lancer outright on the Outward Devourer. You are very keen.
I jumped the gun. Ichigo is playing the Magnus Soodle on Clockwork. Mute 242, otherwise known as lots of swear words. Is playing Phoenix Infernokoi on the Witch Doctor and Watson's Water on Juggernaut, and it's Laue's in the danger zone here.
Does have the doppelganger and he's able to get over to that bomber, and there's now going to be the dive, and Mute is on the hunt. He's running around. This is a long
they haven't got rocket.
Seconds,
they haven't got
so
rocket.
Just walking at him. And he's going to get trapped by the Magnus and what's his water.
He's got the skewer,
pushed him into the tree lines. Laue's going back, but he can't get away. No 5 seconds left, and that's going to be first blood. One of the longest chases around the houses, but they eventually get it done.
Ichigo getting the kill as well on that middle lane. He's actually just bought a bottle. He has a bottle at 0 minutes.
0 minutes, and there's now going to be a bounty given down, but it's
probably going to be for the Phoenix, I'd say. Mm. Unless, no, it's mine, says Ichigo.
Ichigo is a greedy man.
Draft me a greedy middle.
And this is what we're going to see now. The courier will be walking down, obviously going the long route, because it started going through bot, but then it'll be up to the middle. So, good start for Ichigo.
And a terrible start for Laue on the Phantom Lancer. He's going to miss a creep wave as well.
Not what they were looking for, really not what they were looking for indeed. So Chocolate in the middle is going to be cute and prisoning
He's going to take Empower as well, he's already level 2. I'm just going to use that instead of Shockwave, because it's much lower mana cost. And even if he gets put in the magic box lots and lots of times, he'll still have enough mana to cast it and get that additional right-click damage in to last it.
Well,
obviously he's probably not going to win the matchup anyway, because OD is a monster in lane.
Yeah, absolutely.
In the box. You see, you put him in the box and you deny the creep there, which is the correct way to use that skill, boys and girls.
Okay, just walks up here. Just trying to
see if he gets a position of skewer, but already hitting like a bus with a right click, so that stolen entity's got 2 stacks of it, hitting for 78 damage.
I'm sure the wolf's dead for this up top, if that probably was hit by a stomp, so he's just backing out. Or
he's brought Rip pretty low there. Of course, got tankers, so it's fine. Centaur bringing lots and lots of tankers to length. He can happily trade with support if necessary.
and walking at Ichigo in the mid lane. He's currently sitting on around 5-2, and he's going to be doing okay right now. Obviously, vertically with out here in the safe lane, they're going to be looking to see if they can just try and harass that center. Naturally, with retire, it's quite annoying to do, but they have got the regen available.
Sudo's doing pretty well on the spot lane, actually. He's already got level 3 under 2 minutes into the game. Yeah. Nice, not quite matching that, only halfway through level 2.
So Sudo wasn't there for the assist, I believe he did get...
he would have got the XP, yeah, I think, he was in range.
I believe, yeah, he was
They were all chasing him.
It did help him out to really...
Yeah, yeah. But he's also, like, he's just standing in the creep wave. The supports can't stop him. Mm. I don't know why they actually can go there.
Well, obviously Laowei on the Phantom Lance, so you don't have to. How does that matter for the Lance even because of the cogs? Okay, you got the Lion Stone.
It's a sad start to the game. I mean, on the bright side, though Ichigo's just got DD room, so he should get some more lost hits here. Ichigo is being put firmly in the bin by Chocolate in the mid lane. This is a 15 lost hits to 1. That's quite a significant advantage being built by the Outworld Devourer. Is that his name now?
Chocolate, yeah, will bring out boots.
I was right,
and
guys.
There will be boots for Centaur as well. At some point.
There. Centaur stomping centaurs.
Cast thrown out, unfortunately, too far away from the creep. They actually get more valuable attacks by them down there.
He's
actually dive through, gets the stomp as he dives through.
Stomp edge! Oh, he's made a mistake!
Are you kidding me? Wow, that was...
Well played from Nice. He gets a nice kill to answer the first blood. Mute immediately regretting his decision there.
Yeah. It's a case of when you get to the drive through, you're going to be leaving yourself vulnerable to that stomp.
And it was perfectly timed. It was
just
perfectly timed.
Oh, man. Okay,
Druids are in high spirits after that one. There is some...
Obviously, after giving a first blood away like they did, they could be a little bit upset, but they could easily come back.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about how Lara's on a great start here, but he's rebounding pretty nicely, up to 18 last hits, 3.5 minutes into
out. There's going to be a bounce, but it doesn't bounce back. There's the burn free, center. Doesn't have the magical storm, and there's going to be the wave fury as well. They're going to go for the dive. Happy to just keep burning it down. Nice may have got a kill. Tries to hide to the tree line, but he goes to eat his way free. Once more, not going to
his tranquil boots arrive.
And now there's going to be tranquil surviving.
What? That's frustrating for Ichigo. In the bottom lane, meanwhile, as I was saying, this Phantom Lancer has managed to recoup his losses from that early death. That's 20 last hits in a contested lane, because Sudo isn't afraid of him. Yeah, there you go, more cogs pushing him away.
Bumpy, thrown out on the line. He's got that bottle, as you were saying, so just topped himself back up straight away. And there's a rune down bot, one of these ones.
Magnus still in the hole against this OD in the mid lane. Not surprising, I'm not sure why I continue to comment on it, but should emphasize that this is a big lane win. OD, he's almost a full level up thanks to judicious use of imprisonment to deny XP. Of course, when you're in that box, you...
There's now the Fisher Sudo. Gotta be getting focused up, gets the X up. Element taking a fair bit of damage. Sudo wants to try and fish him off. Unfortunately, weren't able to get...
The creeps!
And Sudo will die. Ooh. The creep takes him incredibly
7
low.
HP.
7 HP. And he's now being subbed up with a Clarity as well. So Element still standing. And Sudo will go down.
The aggro was taken off him by one of the other heroes, so well played by them.
So OD has got magical onto him and will be farming up.
Despite giving up
the Midas.
Yeah, despite giving up that first blood, they are turning it around nice and sharpish here, Druids. And they're narrowly ahead by most metrics at this point.
Okay, so Shocker and the next victory just farming up. There is some potential for some Dota 2.
Some Dota 2. Laowei got put in some cogs in the bot lane, and actually, Sudo's having a go here.
Yeah, it's a lot of damage, but then again, Sudo can kind of get away with this, and he's like, okay, well, no one's coming out, so something's afoot.
He's definitely messing with the...
Ichigo, there we go, he is now going to be hit with the imprisonment. There's the Hex, the Fisher is just waiting, hold it out, and Ichigo, they even dropped
well.
The Santa, he's in clips! And there's your mid laner dead. Chocolate will just get that kill off. So... Okay, Magnus down. Give us some time to just get you more fun. Nice, just waiting here. Mute and Co. Just going to be standing out, trying to zone him out again. Disrupt the pulls through. Actually, Wiz can get it off there.
He's got his,
edge. Just going to try and farm it up. Walter's Ward, look at his farm. He's now got his phase onto 482 gold. The carrier will be flying out, and that's going
to be... Watson's not having a great time, actually, given that he's pretty much... I mean, Nice has done really well to disrupt, but... He hasn't been at the creeps much compared to Sudo, who's been at the creeps, and Laowei is still outlast hitting him. You know, Sudo's been a much more irritating offlaner to be against than Nyze.
Well, let's see what they can catch out here. So, Nyze on the centaur still running around. There has been a bottle there.
has got its eyes on the top rune at the moment. And there's your Midas Alfredi, so he's going to be able to keep himself top of the farm. And he's currently sitting at 44 last minutes, so the farm's still going to be going his way. Maybe down onto the line of the moment, so it's quite awkward for them to try and mess with Sudo. Sudo actually gets the hookshot back in, but wants to go for the Kog, so actually he's still caught up for over 2 seconds.
Forced to change
mana
his
being
mind.
Drained, and yeah, Sudo's running away now.
There's he's got TP. Enough health, but the TP, that is from Inferno.
Who just froze the cask out just to clear this out. So Sudo maybe should have waited a second or so. But,
yeah, that's a minor misplay, but he's got a bottle, so he'll
it might have been the case that he saw the opportunity and he thought he could stay close to it, but that's fine.
Element joining the fun down here. Are they going to try and make a go? Sudo's been style back to full HP.
Stomp, which has now been baited out, and there's going to be the victory throw with the Burnie. Now Bomb Stampede goes to double edge, muted again. The
oh, he's going to. No!
That's the kill. Well, he gets the counter kill.
He gets him with the burn, yeah.
So the big bird keeps flying in, gets focused down. Phoenix just goes in and has to die for this. And we're now
surrounded. Sudo's got behind Flower here. This doesn't know that it's going to matter much. He's just going to give him some battery assault and irritate him.
Well, checking out the scores. Sentinel has got 2 kills up in the soft lane, 1 death onto him. ODU has got 1 as well. And it seems that the sports have been doing a lot so far onto Druids. They have got that Earthshaker Lion. They would hit more. Sudo's getting all his mana drains, who is going to be pretty annoyed. But the 8-minute rune's going to be coming up, and he's going to be getting that into ball, which is an illusion.
They've got pretty good rune control this game, given that Odie, of course, doesn't go for a bottle. He's not really focusing on the rune, he's just focusing on getting all those creeps in the mid. So unless the supports contest, and Sudo always contests spot a rune, and Ichigo usually gets the top one. It's gone really well for them on that front. Attack. Not been able to convert it, really.
That's the stats just trying to be cleared up. Going to be flaring it, steal the last hit also. And obviously Double Edge is just going to keep utilised. I want to try and get that blink onto the Centaur as soon as possible. Four staff could be coming out to OD shortly if they were able to keep getting that farming. And the Centaur's now going to just be clearing these illusions. It's like, okay, let's get rid of their eyes in this jungle and see what can happen. So, 4-2 now. Cameraman, what are you feeling about the team's chances here?
It's a close game so far. As I said, I think Druids have an hour advantage by most ways you can measure it, but it could all change if Watsons can start converting on his farm. He is starting to farm at a more rapid rate here. He's on his way to the trademark Mask of Madness, which everyone's getting on Jug at the moment. He's most of the way there to it.
Yeah, Mask of Madness also.
The big problem, of course, is just Magnus is not going to have his Blink Dagger anytime soon. It's 9 minutes in, and he is, you know, he's not going to have it until 15 minutes. He's starting to do jungle stacks now, which will speed things up.
Sudo will pick up this phase, so let's see if Earthshaker set up here top and he gets on his PS. There was a creep getting killed near a tower. Juggernaut has got on the Sash Fable, and normally you see Juggernaut get that level 6, just go for the kill, whoever throws down in there. Unfortunately, that is potential to happen. And here we go, Stampede, there's your Hex. Now Watson's War going to get caught out. There's the Stomp and the Double Edge, and it looks like Watson's War is just going to die. Magnus comes
arrives.
In.
He's going to go for the RP.
Ready. Gets the RP on 2. And this is the Phoenix getting the burn. This could be at least 2 return kills. Nice. Going to be going down here. There's going to be burn onto him, and this is going to be a double. This time the Phoenix won't be killed.
Nice iceberg manning up, but he's actually just short of level 6, so he won't have the finger to finish off Phoenix.
That would have been lovely if he just comes back and gets the return kill there, so it would have been 2-2. So Juggernaut does die at the exchange, that was a smoke being utilised, so naturally...
Yeah, I mean, look at the recap though, just the rubber banding already, because there was an arrow lead for Ichigo, he's done really well off that 600 gold up on the affair.
So, rune top, it'll be going the way of the Magnus top this bottle up, and there's your 4 stuff onto OD.
Ridiculous farm on this Owl Devourer. So of course, the problem is a BKB counters the hero, so you can put all this farm on him, but he just isn't effective if you start buying BKBs. On the other side of Ichigo, don't have any natural BKB bars on their team, not as a major first item. Of course, free magic immunity from the spin often leads Juggernaut players to ignore it for a bit, and Clockwork and Mag have more pressing concerns in their item choices. We shall see, though, maybe.
So Phoenix utilizes this time, whereas the Juggernaut's gone just to be farming up. Juggernaut's now at this Ancients, just trying to clear this out and get that stack going. He has got the Empower there at the moment, so he is taking this. But this is only a just level 2 Empower. It's just the Juggernaut's missing that. These eyes at the moment. So he's going to be farming this fairly quickly, and we've got Sudo with the phase just standing out here. And there's going to be the Stampede. Oh, Sudo hits up. There's the finger. Wow, man. Thank you, man. They get that kill quite quickly. And, hey. they use their spells for it. They come in, they use Stampede. It was always going to result in something. There was the finger.
Spirits are really up on the Druids, boys. I think that victory's given them a lot of... victory in the last game has given them a lot of belief in themselves, which they might have lacked, given that they've not taken a map off. They had taken a map off, which go prior to it. There's lots of happy and quite loud talking coming, which I can hear over the in-game sounds on this. Apparently, is this these headsets? We're wearing headsets.
We are wearing headsets.
and there's a pause.
So let's
shout out to Element.
What the issues are there?
I think it might be lag.
Yep, probably more lag here. So if you just joined us, this is Druids v Ichigo. And yeah, we have been disconnected.
Dear.
So
we'll be
dropping off this screen a second and then seeing if we can.
Hello?
Hello.
I'm the only one left in the game.
Penguin stands alone, ready to look at just five...
So there's lots of red logos. If people could...
We are going to try and reconnect pretty sharply. Hopefully we'll be back into this game. Actually, this is the first...
This finals, we've done really well. There's lots of confusion. It's not looking like it's actually loading back for anyone.
Take a while. We'll be jumping straight back over now as they do unpause the tech issues. I'm not actually going to say anything about the tech issues. They're not happening right now. That's what I'm going to say.
And we are back in the game, 12 minutes deep.
Right.
Two games still on to Ichigo right now. And Druids are currently looking pretty good to at least challenge for this fourth fixture.
Good. We got there in the end, man.
Yeah.
So, what happened? We were 12 minutes of the game, 6-4 at the moment. It is Druids lead the way with 6 kills, but there has been quite a few exchanges. And see what's going on here. We've got Phoenix sitting down, wants to be building up that Midas eventually. This was the support Phoenix, and there is just going to be a bounty picked up from the OD. It's going to be rotating back around. So. What was the name of the game so far? Druids were picking up their kills, but they were getting some exchange kills onto Ichigo every time they won.
Ichigo's nearly got his Blink Dagger, which is a pretty good turnaround given how miserably he was doing to start with.
There was a nice two-man RP top, which really resulted in 2 kills.
It's done well for his money. He will have it presently, pretty much, 20 gold off.
But naturally, the Watson's War had to die for those two, so...
Watson's is still doing okay, though. His net worth is holding pretty steady with the Phantom Lancer, who is his direct opponent on the map.
So... Line retain, going to be up, seeing what they can find out.
Sudo being left to push the lane at the bottom, by the way. He's getting a lot of space on his clockwork.
And there is a V item. Ichigo now down bot. Phantom Lancer is here. Looks to be building that drums up, has got his treads as well.
He's gone for both.
And an Aquila,
he's gone for both the early game sort of transition items that people like to get on the Phantom Lancer. We'll see if that comes back to hurt him as there's a group up middle, look at things.
They may obviously having OD in the mid lane, they are going to just try and see if they can continue to farm them up and continue to stay in the gold game. It has always been in Druid's favour after the... That is a buggy grass, sorry, I'm just looking at that, well... ignore it.
It's what pauses due to grass in this game, boys.
And Witch Doctor uses an OD. Nearly goes down, 85 HP. The Phoenix wants to go for it.
He misses the fall.
This is it, and the Shockwave doesn't hit as well. And there is. Nice. Just nearly going down. So OD.
Druid's hype has not been restrained by that pause, by the way, guys. They are still.
You cannot kill their vibe. They are going to try and get more, and they are mouthing off. I think that's the way to say it. But it's good. It's the
this is all part of the joys of LAN, being able to taunt
opponents live stage, able to get there, and then just shout at them while she makes plays.
I've turned the vision off.
F1, F2, F3.
Have I done that?
There you go. See, I'll let you off as you're not normally a caster, else I would have been flaming.
You can flame me anyway.
Okay. But my flame is relentless and I'll do it off stream. So 1,000 gold onto Earthshaker here in the mid lane, and they are going to be good.
In that break, all I did was. Wasn't and Ichigo are going to push the top tower down for Ichigo. That is actually the first tower to fall this game. So a nice injection of pennies into Ichigo's bank account.
Water's Wars to continue to farm up the jungle.
And actually, drag the gold graph back to dead even at 50 minutes. We have a close game on our hands here, Rusts.
Well, let's see who can take the next series of fights. The hookshot fired out from Sudo, unable to catch him. And obviously, you're going for a Phantom Lancer, he was going to be able to try a doppelganger out. But there is the battery assault to try and keep him in place. Get that damage in and see what they can get. So Magnus has got that blink
And
there's a wall of wards coming out here from druids there, trying to take control of vision around the Roche area.
Well, they know, obviously, they want to keep eyes on Manus coming in with the potential for clockwork.
Look at the Roche bit. Is that, does that sentry see that?
No. It's just outside, okay. But no. Unfortunately, not able to see.
Game of inches. As Centaur finishes his item, his key item, really. This decent timing from Nye. Not as.
Magnus Blinkson tries to get back, but unfortunately, just going to be Ash in the prison. That is going to be a Fisher. A little bit early. It's just able
time
to
from Element.
Head over the racing line.
He had a near flawless game last game on the Shaker. This time, that's a slight error from him. Yeah, the farm isn't so strong from Druids this game. It's a slow blink dagger by comparison on Centaur. And. Element's still a long way off his own as well.
So Stampede is still out. They can try to go for this catch. Bear in mind, Ichigo did go in for that, and then it looked like there might be potential to try and take down. Unfortunately, we've actually missed that fish, but even so, it looks like Ichigo would have taken some damage and still been able to just secure himself over that. So, looking at the farm, is this the sort of picture you expected? Obviously, we talked about OD's dominance in the lane, talked about Juggernaut getting it.
PL's farm has slowed down, actually. It's in comparison to Watson's, who is. He's marked himself out as a clear second place on the list now. And Ichigo is recovering pretty well from his struggles in the early game. Those kills helped him. He's got some stacks in the jungle made for him by supports too. As the Centaur ult comes out, and they're going to use it to go on Soodle at the bot lane.
Mew
comes in, he doesn't even bother token over there. He knows his offlane has died.
He doesn't actually have the mana there.
No,
this is a potential catch. He does get hit by the lads. Unfortunately, they don't want to go in. There was no blink for 2 seconds.
They just saw the Mag turn up, and of course he has RP and Skewer. They're going to chase though, and dear.
Laue gets it off, maybe able to finish that last spirit lance, which finishes the kill. But as this happens, up top, Watson's Wall was just standing there for the TP. He's like, you want to come in? I'm ready with my Omni Slash, baby.
It's level 2 Omni Slash already. He's already got 11, so good play. I'm going to group here in the bottom lane.
So, something I didn't mention as well earlier on, when their Omni Slash does come out, they will be empowered. Here we go. Laue able to hit the doppelganger there as the Ichigo blinks in. Obviously, realizes the Magnus is coming in, but they get the catch. He's able to dodge that off and then get away.
A big play from Laue.
Warwick will deny the tower, though. So, okay, the cooldown's down. That's 95 seconds. They know they've got that window of opportunity and potentially able to make something with it. Sight now up.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Do you reckon they should just be letting this tower go? They will hit the forks, obviously. That is a tier 1.
They don't
one.
Have RP.
SMY
but they do have Jug's, Omni, of course, and Sun, and look at it go. They have a lot of good spells they can use here if they want to start a fight, and Druids realise this is back off. Druids, of course, not without their own teamfight presence with Odie's ult and Element's kit as well, and Centaur's ulti as well. As I say, as well, too much.
As well, yes.
I think I've become Josho, guys.
Oh, God. Another shout out to Josho. Don't be blaming him. So, down bot, we have got Centaur running, seeing if he can find anyone. And there is just going to be some people running on that. Soodle will just be backing out, not going for any more plays with the hookshot. Going to be building up towards that blade mill.
Watson's already hitting like a boss. He has 200 damage with the power on him. Of course, he can crit as well. About to finish the Sandra, give him another boost. And the main chance, of course, which everybody tends to overlook.
Out, Chocolate. He has got that big nuke he can bring down, but the blade mail usage, there was, I think, a game yesterday. I think it was only the once. I'm not sure if it was a couple of times, but he did blow himself up, so obviously he's going to have to be careful of that again. And the surprise flavor when he first comes out of it, you're like, oh, drop my spells. Oh, never mind, I've killed myself. Yeah.
And
this
is
now
going to
be
sent
off in the mid lane.
Trouble.
Oh, Ichigo gets pulled out, and
absolutely
there is your sanity clip.
Annihilated. Pai's a really dead hero.
Very dead. So, Ichigo again dead. RP is.
We talked about how this was a really close game. It looks like Druids are the ones who are grabbing it by the scruff of the neck here, taking command. They have once again built a decent gold lead, and the XP is heading into their favour for the first time in the game as well.
Yeah, this. Not in between them. There is a minus
it's
up.
It's still, of course, really close.
Yeah, there is a minus up onto OD, as well as obviously having the minus being built up.
Soodle finishes blade mail.
Nice.
OD looks like it's probably going for. There's Mutes Midas on his support Phoenix. As OD is building towards a side of Vice, of course, great for the int, which gives you that pure damage on the Arcane Orb.
So, we will see Element just continue to
Farmer Pip, 2 gold off. There we go. Got his
gold. Radiant's top tower
we'll
is
see
under
if
attack.
Able to make the play with it. So Soodle just coming around towards the mid lane. Got to be looking to see if there's any opportunities and stacking up his ancients.
Cool.
At the
cooldowns are all up for Ichigo. That might be the time to make something happen. Stampede will be off shortly, but there will be no Sanity's Eclipse for over a minute still.
Well, the final answer has got his Preds, has got his Zergram, and now picked up a Yasha.
See if he finishes the Mantua or goes back for
this might be a blade.
Yeah,
that's also you can see like Final Lancers get like the Vlad's Diffusers sort of thing. And Scaddy as well, ridiculously nice. Oh. Final Lancers and Fights. Then again, I think I say that near enough anyone who's
it's a very, very popular,
very popular
item. No, I think we haven't seen it yet this series, so
actually, yeah, you're correct, I think. So, Watson's War will just be...
Watson's farm starting to ratchet up. Despite lacking that Midas, he has just overtaken OD for net worth. This guy having... Can we call it a breakout land?
Oh,
or is it a hookshot misses from Soodle?
Hookshot.
He was aiming it into the woods at this OD. And I'm not sure he wants to go on that. I guess he has the blade mail now, but still...
Yeah, he could also pop the cogs down, fight up against the
Assault,
OD. OD then has to stop fighting him because he's popped the blade mail. Then Soodle kind of just walks his own way. But the rest of his team could be there to help him, and it could have been Soodle dying.
Heck of the Sensor Ulti element.
They just catch
Inferno, but he's blocked. The tree blocked the chase, and Inferno is going to be...
Could go for a castle, actually.
He's a bit animation, but he gets away. And
that would have been nice if he got that TP castle.
It's going to be a nothing happening. I do waste the Sensor Ult still, which means there's another window of opportunity here, but Sanity's Eclipse has just come off cooldown. For the Outworld Devourer.
Infernoquoy dying for a... Infernoquoy, sorry, living for a Stampede.
Yeah, it was a slight misplay from the Earthshaker. It was the correct Fissure Line to block him from retreating, but it also blocked his entire team, and Lao Wai wasn't there with the Cunning Blade. He sold his Cunning Blade, actually, so they don't have any way of killing trees anymore. It's a shame.
Yeah, there is the full stuff being built up onto the Magnus now shortly. So... And let's see what they can get.
They're gonna try, despite losing that ultimate, they're gonna attempt to force the issue in the middle lane, grouping up OD finishing the Cypher Vise at 22 minutes on top of a 4-star hand of Midas, not bad. But there is Ichigo's team are here to meet them. Except Watson has TP and will be able to join the fight the instant it starts.
This could be a tense moment. If the Cypher Vise comes out on a key hero before they get, like, say, the RP or the Soodle comes in to counter-initiate, this could be a very good fight for Druids.
Looks like Juggernaut is going for the AoE Scard. He's got an ultimate orb.
Yeah, well, let's see what Watson wants to do. Just farm here. Maybe he's just get this.
He doesn't... Still opting not to go for that... BKB against the OD. Not doesn't think it's worth it. He's a 4-star. He's picked up by Sentinel. That means they've got 2 4-stars on the team now because there's one on the OD as well.
This is going to be hard for them. Lion?
They have less natural ability on this team, of course, other than the Sentinel world. So these 4-stars to work to offset that. And Mag also picking up a 4-star. 4-star gaming.
Yeah, 4-star gaming. They're going to see.
No Yule Scepters this game as well. Are we sure on the right patch, guys?
Hey, 4-star can be pretty damn tasty, and the mid lane has been the fight ruin. You can see heroes just standing.
All 5 heroes in the region.
We'll still try and go for this. We're gonna just get his nice last hits out here. Just keep the farm going and try not to do anything.
Watson's is really sticking it to OD. He's opened up like 1,500 gold lead now.
Oh, Element Blixing gets the Fissure off now. There's now your Stomp and your Double Edge, and there's another 2-man RP, but then there's going to be Sue to get the Hookshot off. Unfortunately, not able to get it.
The Omni Slash ended prematurely.
Gets the kill onto Lion. There's now Sally's Eclipse, which hits onto them, and they are just backing out here. Fanart against the tower, could try and finish up Infernoquoy, and there is.
He jukes him through the trees.
Well.
He does doppelganger forward.
There's the Lance, hits onto
him.
He does
the
have the rush. Infernoquoy will throw out a cast, and it's
going
to be a turn. Watson's Ward goes in, gets the help. There's now an Imprisonment, and Phoenix dives through, gets the Nova off, and he now goes to double again. And this is going to be where Fanlancer tries to throw those lances out.
Oh,
big Echo Swam comes in from Element. We see Ichigo get focused on, will bring him back with him. He's like, oh, this is what I planned. He'll come up here from the Big Bird, but unfortunately, Earthshaker will not be
able to
wait. Actually, doesn't have his blink available. Ichigo's still standing, and this could be another kill. Element will go down here.
Nice dropped Infernoquoy on the back lines, but yep, it's still, I think, a trade in favor of.
Well,
what does the gold say? Yeah, it is a trade in favour of Ichigo. Big XP jump for them.
2-for-1 there, and there's now going to be a smoke purchase.
That was a Phantom Lancer. He's very high level, of course, level 14.
Yeah, I could see obviously why he went for it. Like, you know, the Inferno was very low onto the Witch Doctor. I did eventually die, but.
Yep.
A case of too deep.
It was diving too deep for a hero, not worth the money. And Inferno's dead body was like back out on the other side past the Dire Ancient, so he ran all the way around and met into and bumped into the Centaur who was coming around to support the fight on the high ground. So he was actually free if he had gone the other way across towards the tier two.
Check out the last hits. We have Chuggalore. It's in at 235. Phantom Lancer has. Took over to the OD, and there's now your Scardy up onto Chuggalore.
Watson, after, you know, he didn't have the greatest start farming, he was struggling in the sort of first 5 minutes, but since then he's been on fire, 250 last hits already. Sanjanyasha, Mask of Madness, Eye of Scardy, all nice and finished. We'll see what he goes for next.
Yeah, this is the last game in this, potential last game if Ichigo wins. So obviously Druids
like
have got to be trying their hardest now
to
come back into this and really try.
We should be selling like they're behind. It's an incredibly close game.
This is easy potential for both teams to take this victory, but it's just a case of who's got to be one out their A game here trying to focus this up.
Something could be brewing up here as we have four heroes gathering from one team and on their way for the other, about the same number it looks like.
The Empower onto a Juggernaut. Juggernaut's already obviously got ridiculously nice base stats just with Phase, Mask and Mana, so you've got a lot of damage now.
He's also gone for a lot of stats, you know, without maxing Fury and Healing Ward. The build at the moment, of course, nothing particularly remarkable in that.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Right, so the situation's going to be defused. We won't have a fight right there as Druids head towards the middle lane. And TP more to the bot.
So, okay, there has been a bit of a lull in the fights now at the moment. They have got the Phoenix with the Midas. He wants to go continue using that. Soodle has just got his Phase Blade Melt, and they are going to try and make more happen now. So, Ichigo has got his Blink 4-star.
Talking about Laowai's Arm Choice, that net worth is probably a bit deceptive. I don't think he's actually that high up, given that he has Drums, Aquila, two items which, you know, take up your gold and don't actually give you huge amounts of effect as we head towards what's, you know, the later mid-game. Compared to Watson's, as we have a go in the middle lane, Ichigo in trouble.
Again, blown up. He's going to need to get a BKB when they want to be. Literally, it's his next time. He should go for BKB. And then he'll be able to do a lot more. Obviously, these are getting catches. Pops that beep, blinking. Yeah, catch someone, and that's going to be.
Yeah, I mean, looking at the net worth at the moment, it's three of the top four in the hands of Druids. Soodle whiffs on the hookshot.
Able to catch anyone there.
But the top hero is still Watson's Water. 2,000 gold clear of everybody else. His next item? Do you have an opinion on his next item, Russ?
Whose story was that?
Watson's.
Oh, Watson's Ward's next item. Well, he has got his. Actually, he might be one again to BKB as well.
I think so. I mean, obviously, as a Juggernaut, you're low to pick one up given your free magic immunity button, but it doesn't allow you to get the same amount of damage on as the game wears later and you just want to right click. Looks like the top tower is going to go down here. Let's see if Ichigo and Co can get themselves a trade.
We'll just get that tier 1 up. Nice, taking the last hit there. And he is going to be improving. That's no stampede, 13 seconds. And just checking out here. They are still doing their work, but what can they
do? It's a nice ancient stack, too. As it looks like Druids have cottoned on as Ichigo clears out the Lancer illusions before they actually see what's going on, but I'm sure they can make assumptions when there's
no one's coming in the pit. So that is going
to
be.
They do grab the Aegis, and it looks like they're going to head to the top, maybe?
3,200 gold onto the Juggernaut. Let me see what he wants to go for.
He might be holding on at this point. His respawn time is already pretty long given that he's level 19. I think buyback is becoming a requisite.
And it seems the Druids are just going to flee from top, which is the fight.
They're going to send the Lance Illusions into the tower, though, which will do some about half damage, actually. That's some work.
They're going to be getting the tier 1 for it. Okay, Roshan went down, but did they really want to fight into a pit? RP, Phoenix?
I think it was the right play, and they've done some good chip to the tower as well there.
So, checking out the XP. Still in Ichigo's favour at the moment. It feels like. Phantom Lancer has got 2-1 at the moment. He's building up the diffuser. When the diffuser comes online, are we going to see a different sort of game from him? Because he's been farming.
He's been farming and split pushing as much as he can. He's turned up to fights, but I think it's the way Laue plays most of his carries, really. He doesn't, you know, he lets his team do their stuff. He did the same in his anti-mage. He had about 5 kill participations in that game, and his team had killed 30 heroes by the end. And it's just the way he plays the hero. He likes to farm for a bit and then turn up. And he's doing well, though not as well as Watson's in this game, so we'll see how they link up. Of course, with Empower, Watson's can actually make good speed for the Phantom Lancer.
So that tier 1 in mid lane will be going down and up.
They're going to keep going here and try and force the TPs back. It looks like a trade will be the play Druids want to go for, with Lancer and OD both gathered down here, but they are going to force TPs back. Elements here. Soothal's invisible behind the tower. They don't know he's there.
Two. Fortification now being forced. There is
oh, the hookshot in on Elements.
Catching on Element. Element now being forced up and out, and now Soothal is just going to back out. No mana left, but this would be a tier 2. Soothal just makes that space. It's just like, I'll go in, guys. Grab that tower once I've gone. And Diffusal now up onto PR.
6,000 gold on that Juggernaut. He's making a mint. Yeah. We'll see if he does go for that BKB or maybe a stats item, maybe a butterfly.
Yeah, just get a butterfly arrow attacking even quicker. We'll
go
going to
go for the basher though.
So get the abyssal out, and this could be a nice cool. He's obviously not feeling scared at all, has got the Aegis on
him. The OD doesn't worry him, it turns out. I'm not sure if it's the right play. OD does have Hex, he's on his way to the Shiva's Guard next.
Well, as he's only died once, so this was in the early phase so far, he doesn't feel
he has got support.
And once this war is going to be able to tear through them, just empower and all this. I think actually getting
He does more damage. You end up right click about he's going to beat the OD. It's if he gets locked down and the OD's allowed to wail on him, because he'll hit for like 500 damage at the moment.
True. Now with the Omni Slash, they can be using that Abyssal Drone and just guaranteeing that he gets one of the kills. As long as nothing goes too wrong with the bounces. But no Ghost Scepters out onto OP or I believe any of the Rain Team. Just actually quickly check their things. Yeah, no Ghost Scepters out there. But
the big basher's finished. He's actually elected to go up on his buyback to finish it.
Straight into Mega Basher. Missile is there. There is now going to be another right map for OD. You've got Shiva is there with his force off and his.
OD also without buyback. There's potential for the spikes to
have a tier 2 go.
They fight, but they're just going to give up a tier 2. This is exactly what happened to them to HGO last game. They're getting slowly shoved back into their corner of the map because they're scared to fight into this Juggernaut, who is huge. He's 5,000 gold ahead of OD now.
Yeah.
And, you know, 8,000 ahead of this PL, who is struggling for relevance at this point.
This could really be the next team fight. He's still got Aegis. This could really be a game deciding play and potentially a series deciding play here.
Yeah. Looks like Nyze is actually going for a BKB after we've talked about how we think HK need to buy them. It's the Centaur on Druids who's making the move towards that item right now.
Well, Soodle, HK retain up to top, but it looks like
Laue. Soodle has just bought an Oak Club. Okay, he's going for a BKB too. That makes me feel a little bit better about my calls.
Well, he has a bit of focus to run it, but let's see. The four star.
Has he? Am I being blind?
Oh. Sorry, I'm not here to shoot you down every 2 minutes, but you could still go for BKB as well, but yeah, you know, the opportunities are all over the place. So Watson's Water here, 2,700 gold onto him. I do feel like, being genuine, the BKB is a good shout there, because obviously all of these heroes can potentially catch them and disrupt this team fight and potentially just win them fight for
it. It's something you notice about Druid's drafting, they've brought fighter tables in each game, you know, each hero has something.
BKB,
which stops you doing your team fight.
Fisher comes up, we'll connect onto
him. He's got Aegis still. How long is that? That has not got too long left on it, though, has it? It's about a minute left on that Aegis.
True, yeah. About a minute left on the Aegis. And there's going to be the. Radiant's top tower. There's going to be a tower being pushed down.
It's a trade, though, because Laue got the tier 1 bot.
Edgar shows himself. He thought he was illusion serve. He does get traded out pretty quickly. He does four stuff away and takes a fair amount of his mana gone. And we're now going to see OD rotating around. Has got his bite this off quite at around about 10 seconds. He's going to be taking that farm in the mid lane. Soodle & Co. up here top. Walking through. Going to be continuing to farm on 2,400 gold. Bear in mind, he had this gold like just a bit earlier. You expect
to
see
his
something.
His farm is actually ridiculous. Yeah. I mean, he's benefiting from having the Magnus to grant him in power at times. Of course, Mask of Madness also increases your farm speed. This hero is really good. He also runs fast normally with phase, and that's 468 movement speed with phase active before he uses mask, before he gets empowered, which doesn't give him movement speed. I'm an idiot.
And
he hits for a lot of damage. That was the thought which I didn't complete. His team have also been fantastically efficient. There's been an extra stack for him every time he's needed one. He's actually going to give some of this to Ichigo, who is still struggling for gold. He's going for a BKB. Given. not having the influential game we're used to seeing from the talismanic captain of Ichigo.
1-4 problem at the moment. Yeah, there has been some catches, and I really like this juggernaut. I would just get that blink dagger up. I think maybe this is what they need, because the stampede, the catches potential, and seeing what they can find, this could be
arriving. They're going to go. Poor old Phoenix, dead before he even gets to press a button.
Blown up.
Yeah. They only used one cooldown for that, too. They can maybe keep going. Are they going to try and force their way into this tier 2?
So maybe with Stabby Fisher is just the Phoenix just dying there. Gets a bit of gold there going their way. So we can try and go for a disruptor.
They spot out Ichigo.
Double down. Edge. BKB forced now, and now Sudo just pops the fable and backs out. There is the buyback from Mute. He has got the Phoenix here, but are they just going
to
let this tower go?
They have
the
buyback on Ichigo too if they need to. I don't think they'll...
But forcing two buybacks here, the radiant could just be back, I think it's probably the play is to leave it.
I'm not sure why Mute bought back. I think they have to... They're gonna hold it maybe with Fire Spirits. Is it worth the money? Phoenix has actually finished his BKB, so
the tower could be going down very shortly. And Lowry just wants to get this.
They have got Glyph
now,
but they're gonna save it. I think in case they try and force the high ground.
Tier 2 will go down. Buyback was forced from the Phoenix. Say about force, but it was used for the Phoenix.
It was good for Druids. They've retaken the net lead.
Yeah, really nice. Getting two catches back to back, because obviously this catch over here, the Phoenix was just disintegrated. Then you find the Magnus just over here.
Yeah, they've got a ward up here. That's how he was seen. It's a good ward. And of course, Ichigo was standing there, so it's totally visible. And obviously,
you knew exactly where it was from
that kill. And
just like, guys, they saw me. They got vision and a bit of travel now up onto.
He's even faster now, team.
This is nice. Wait, where did he? I did buy a blink dagger, if I got insane.
No, I don't think he did.
Did he not?
I didn't want to call you an idiot.
Oh, well, then I have legitimately gone insane, which wouldn't be the first time here. Maybe it was the lion and I've just looked at a juggernaut's face.
We're all mad here.
Anyway, it's, we're doing good. So, best of 5, Ichigo v Druids, and now Soodle's here. So apologies for that mystical turn. Mistakes have been made.
Still 2 games.
Whoops.
2 games to 1 in this final as we tick into the third hour of play.
Yeah.
We could be going to another game, it looks like. Druids. This game is still, of course, very close with Watson's Water possessing such ludicrous amounts of farmed. He's actually kept the phase boots in his inventory, by the way, until he gets another item. This is efficiency. He can still activate the phase boots movement speed boost, and they still get the right-click damage from it, of course. No movement speed. You can only get it using 1 set of boots, of course, in 32. But when he activates his phase boots now, he has max move speed, or what used to be max move speed before they took the cap off.
So, okay.
Agadin's finally finished on clock. He's not had a stellar game. Honestly, all of Ichigo's not had a stellar game outside of Watson's, who is doing a large amount of work. I guess Infernoquoi hasn't... He's not been bad either, but he's just struggled to affect it. You often do that as a 5 roll when your team falls behind, of course. It's not necessarily on him, but Ichigo and Sudo are struggling to affect the game in the ways they might hope that they could.
Element did get that ghost out as well, so that's really going to help them against this juggernaut menace, which is going to try and force them down.
Well, I think he can die in one... Oh, no, he's got a bit more HP now. Yeah, I think it'll take 2 crits to kill him.
We have seen that there will be a potential issue if Ichigo and Co. want to... defend this high ground. Druids might try and get a pick off, but if Ichigo stand up here,
it looks like we're going to see the last tier 2 on the map go. They're playing it cautious, Druids. They know. And SPL finishes his heart, which makes him even more irritating. 24 armor. Good luck killing him, guys.
2,000 health, and there is no, not going for the Scaly. Obviously with the heart you can kind of go in, tank it up, and then come back and regen rather than Scaly, which obviously does give,
he's still got one more slot. He'll definitely sell the Aquila, probably sell the drums. He's not used a single drum charge, by the way. Where's the value with that? We are 40 minutes into this game. Look at his score. I figured out why he's not.
And then I've got to just send out the fisher onto the groups here and then see what they can clear out and go for it. And as this happens, they are now going to be going towards potential.
They get in time,
and now Sudo comes in with the initiation. He gets pushed out of the cogs, and now they try to stampede away. Let's get out the casks. Actually, he does fix bounces there. And now Sudo's just like, okay, whatever, I'll TP away. I'm losing all my mana.
Bye.
Indeed.
And we just had a non-fight there, but nobody actually dying, a freak explosion. And what are they going to do with this Aegis though, Rush? So are they going to try and push themselves? Because they're still really, really behind. Except, you know, if Watsons dies, even though he's got the Aegis, they are in serious trouble. They're not going to win the fight without the guy.
I think it might be a case of Ichigo may have to just get this BKB out before they go for his head spine. There's going to be a potential for a catch. Once more goes in, does get a hit off onto line. The man has been draining.
The chain started, the Aegis is down. They need the team here right now.
Scythe been using the Aegis. Sudo comes in.
He's got Omni Slash. No one to target on. He runs for it.
And
swoops. No ult to use. The Omni's onto. Oh, into the creeps. But Nye still dies. He's stuck on the high ground. He's stuck on the high ground with Laowai. He's going to go down. Element comes in to help. The Echo Slam used as well. And down goes Watson's Water. That huge net worth swing.
And Mute
goes. Oh, Ichigo's in trouble. That's why he's gone. Oh, nice RP. He catches two heroes. Laowai in trouble. He might drop. He does go down. Chocolat also in trouble. Elements is on the high ground. He's going to TP out, I think. Just escaping. Chocolat on the high. He's still on high ground. Watson's is back. Did he buy? Watson's bought back.
Yeah, that was my bad.
So that's why he's there, but he does get the kill on Chocolat, which probably makes it worth it. Look, what does the fight recap say?
Yeah, so let's quickly go through what happened there. So three of Druids do die for the two, but, well, you got to remember, there was actually two deaths with the Juggernaut because he did have the Aegis, came back, respawned, sadly, his Eclipse was used for that first kill onto him, which onto to die, but then you lose the Phantom Arty, you lose the Centaur, you lose the OD.
They did lose all their cores, yeah.
Yeah, this is potential to do a lot more work here, and they've got to try
they
and take
the Ichigo. They have got buybacks on two of those
want
heroes.
To get this now. They have got a fortification, but there is your Ichigo as well.
So they might have to buy at the OD here, I think. Centaur's going to respawn. And there's no buyback on this Phantom Monster though. He's 70 gold short. That's a bit irritating. But it looks like Ichigo are going to do classic Ichigo Dota and play it incredibly safe. Retreat to the river, farm the enemy jungle. It's Ichigo's favourite place, I think.
Yeah, just happy to farm it up all day and all night. So yeah, that team fight, it kind of went a little bit more sideways than we'd hope. Watson's War, I think, wanted to get off his Omni Slash initially as he was coming in, and there was the line of the OD to go. Unfortunately, with the Hex, there's always that fear. That's why I was
Yeah, he was chain disabled down. It was...
Yeah.
He did get the Omni Slash off, but it was a good play from Nye. He force locked himself onto the cliff and into the neutrals, so a lot of the slashes bounced onto the creeps. So... he still died, of course, but he mitigated the damage to the rest of his team.
Yeah, it just forced them a different way. And now the Empowered Juggernaut.
They've got the gem on Jug, by the way. He sold his face boots and put a gem in that slot for now.
Yeah, good to travel gem. Sajin Yasha Abyssal with a Scaddy, and he now passes the gem over to them.
That buyback and death has really shrunk the lead that Jug had, though, to only 2,000 gold now ahead of the OD. Who has got a Ghost Scepter? Is he going for the Magic Earthblade, I think, Ross?
Which
OD has a Ghost Scepter. Do you want to see an Earthblade?
Yeah, maybe getting that out, because obviously you have got this Juggernaut. You want to just be able to Ghost Scepter yourself through that ulti and just stay alive through it. But looking at the Usher, he's also got one, and the Centaur is building towards a Harmonious Valley. Yeah. Still farming around, it's going around, and will
refresher
there be a
Refresher
out from OD?
Oh boy. So that's two Sanity's Eclipse. He is a very smart hero, so that Sanity's Eclipse is doing a lot of damage. He is totting 192 intelligence right now. Let's look at the highest in hero. Who is the highest in hero? They have got a int deficit on this team. It's probably... Yeah, that's a bit flamey, isn't it? It's 66 in on Witch Doctor is the highest on the team, I believe.
I thought you were saying something about the players there.
There's
the BKB. This time, I'm looking at the right hero.
Good
BKB
boy. Well done, Rusts.
Yeah, once it's more, we'll get that through. And I think that is definitely the right
shot. He passes the gem to Mag and will slot the BKB into that slot. So they have got BKBs on their two most important core heroes. Still lacking one on Soodle. And of course, on both of the. Oh no, on just on. Oh, Soodle. There's Soodle going. Really?
Yeah, he is now going in. One man against the world. The rest of the team is just here. They're trying to keep him up. Can they bait them into an RP moment? Ichigo standing behind. And there was a customer nice. Trying to clear off. Fisher out. Doesn't connect. There's a two. Oh! And now there's an Echo Slam. Element comes in. Witch Doctor throws out the ult. And there's a size eclipse. Does the ultimate. Ichigo brings two into the RP with the supernova still going on. They have to try and run to the side. There's not going to be a refresher. He uses Ghost Sip as well. There's the Maledict. And there's fight is still going on. Laowai is going to try and just finish up the Phoenix of the back lines, and now Fanato is tearing through the element, gets another kill, and it's a four man for the center.
I think it's a disaster. Druids. Chocolate living on an inch of HP.
Okay,
he does go down. Can he do it? Can he go ham? I don't think he can. And that is a full wipe for two heroes. This has got to be a set of barracks. They're going to buy them back. They can buy back three of their heroes. They choose to get two of them back on the field. Can Phoenix and can Soodle hold this base? Let's see.
This is using those cogs.
Oh, he's going to rush. Oh no, Soodle die back. He might do. He gets hexed up in danger. Phoenix tries his best, but he can't save him. He goes down. Element stealing the kill with a Fissure. Iceberg pretty low by all the spirits, but it's going to be okay. Now they can go on the... I thought I was going on Phoenix there, but he's going to hit the buildings.
I think it's dead, just try to focus down, they can get a set of racks here,
45 minutes in. It's at the point of the game where a set of racks is not as debilitating as it could be, but still far from optimal, of course, without your buildings. Also, the gold swing from that fight is pretty large. It's over 5,000 gold now, that famous point of no return, that is less so on this current patch with the huge river banding that can happen, but still not a lead you want to give up.
I think hit onto him, there's going to be the laser cover as well. Right. Actually, still trying to finish this through, and there's not going to be the dive coming, and they will take the melee ramps.
They're going to head out though now.
Heading away.
Yeah.
Oh, Ichigo tries to get a catch, unfortunately.
Centaur ult used as well, yeah.
Yeah.
Ichigo is livid. There was a loud shout of what from his casting desk.
48 seconds on that stampede now, and they all go their own way. So, is
under attack. That was a big fight.
Was the refresher used that much?
Yes, he was. That's the only reason he lived so long. He had to refresh. Yeah. He refreshed after scything. He didn't have scythe otherwise. It was big.
Yeah, but that's why the juggernaut getting caught off.
Yeah, he just delayed long enough that his team could come. Chocolate still died in that fight.
Even with a 10 second BKB, may I add. He wasn't able to get it off then.
Did he Omni doing the BKB? I wasn't. Because that's always a problem with.
I believe it was Omni Sash already used and then with the BKB at the end. But I must admit, I may not have caught that.
I'm pretty sure Omni was mid fight. But whatever. It was a really great execution of the fight from Druids who. Have taken a pretty commanding position in this game. Watson's Water still hugely problematic for them. Incredibly rich. A lot of items on that hero. He is six slotted. I mean, what do you... Might maybe upgrade the Mask of Madness to a Satanic. Maybe that's the only thing he can do to improve his current loadout.
He has some change out here. Obviously, you have the Mantle on the Courier pulling around and try and make some plays. For the moment, they haven't really been able to go for this. It's like trying to defend their base, but... Let's see what they can do.
Laowai, on the other hand, is pretty rich right now. He's probably going to get his next item soon. 4,000 gold surplus over his buyback. Is it Butterfly? Is it Skadi? What do you think?
Yeah, he could go Butterfly, but I think Skadi is still pretty nice. Bear in mind, it's impossible. Well, not impossible. It's pretty dang hard to kill at the moment. So
I think what would lead me towards Butterfly is the fact that Watson's hasn't got MKB and he hasn't got a slot for it. He'd have to sell his Sanjanyasha or his. You know,
SMY could
make room
for it. Upgraded.
Yeah,
but obviously it's
and
very
he can,
nice.
As I said, maybe they change the Mask of Madness out of the slot for Satanic if he feels the need to. Just tank up that little bit more.
Fiona Phoenix does have the Yules available as well as his Midas, and they are going to try and make more. So, the Power Jug, we talked it up, but it's been hard for Ichigo to get the...
Yeah, Ichigo's just not been having such a tough game on this Magnus. He's really struggled to affect it. He's been dying a lot. There's no two ways about it. He's got five deaths on that hero, which is more than the average his team should have, especially given that there's not been much death at all from the. He's not died at all. It's that Infernoquai guy. He's only died three times on his hard five. Witch Doctor. What a player.
What a player indeed. So look at those kills and deaths. It's Soodle 062. He has to kind of hookshot himself in, try and disrupt it, but then dies for it. Occasionally, there's been some plays where it's like, I'll hookshot in, try and back out, and then we can try to take a team fight off it. Like that fight middle where we saw all of Ichigo's team die. So, it can be a hard one.
In the calm before the storm again, probably waiting for the objective, the big Roshan spawn, which, if the teams are timed, should be, they not all know it's coming within the next 4 minutes. Exactly when, of course, is a mystery to them. Not to the lovely viewers who can use their eyes.
Looking at them just move through the jungle, it looks like Centaur wants to push up his heart. He still has. This will go through the BKBs quickly. So the BKB onto Centaur is currently sitting at 8 seconds. So Phantom Mantis is
not. Like they're getting another hex on Earthshaker.
Oh, okay, that could be pretty dang tasty. And on the Dire, there's the BKB up on Mute 242 on the Phoenix. That's 8 seconds. We've got Ichigo having an 8 second BKB as well. And obviously, Soodle doesn't have one. He does have his Agonist though, so he's trying to make the.
Four of the top five on the net worth chart now on the Druid side. They are. This gold lead, you see, this is the moment they want to fight on the gold graph, and then it's skyrocketed since they far more effectively. Ichigo's team have started to play scared. They are literally, it's poor Protect Watson at this point. They need him to get all of his stuff off in the fight, and they need him to get it off perfectly. And they, of course, they need a big RP and a big Witch Doctor roll. They need things to go really well. They are behind now as Centaur picks up an item, and we do get that. So that's a second side on their team, along with the Hex.
Yeah, I think this is quite smart. They keep knocking down these people.
It's just, you know, if they kill Watsons, they win the fight. I think they know that. So they're just going to bring all the single target disable. They're going to add to it with the two hexes they've now picked up. It's the play, and the butterfly is the call from Lao Wai.
Lao ready.
Force Watsons into an item that he's not building towards.
So, looking at the site, we can see that Radiant do know that there's heroes up here, so they may be anticipating something, but we'll check what's going on. The Dire will not have sight, and they will not see the Earthshaker, but if you look at what's going on here, they can see something here. But now there's the hook shot from Pseudo, will catch them. There's going to be the RP on two, going to be trying to bring him up. Witch Doctor does miss the mallet, unfortunately a little bit of miscommunication there. There's the Phoenix on top of the hill, and this could be a massive point for Ichigo. They are now getting focused up there, the Fissure comes through. Echo Slam over here isn't actually on the point, but that Watson's War is still standing, it's hexed up for a while. Doesn't have his PKB up, sorry, big fun, and is now going to be trying to fight up against the Knives. Gets the Storm up again, Watson's War getting focused, now getting forced up away. Ichigo getting focused by the Phantom Hunter, and he's still saying it's going to be a triple kill. Never mind, Druids with an Ultra and Roshan.
Oh, are you sure?
Mercy.
Buybacks everywhere.
Buybacks.
Mute's
okay,
still on the
mine.
Cliff.
This is it.
Mute's on the hill.
They're going to try and go for this, but it looks like Roshan's already taken it. Can he go for it? Got to grab the cheese at least. No, he doesn't yet. No.
Oh, no. Mute 242. He's had a feed there, guys. And that means all five heroes died in that fight. They've brought back three heroes. They're all in situ, and Ichigo's in trouble again.
No,
he's going to die. He's getting chased down. The Force Staff's on cooldown. Stampede's on cooldown. Oh, a miss doppelganger. And he gets the Blink Dagger. A misplay from Lao Wai allows Ichigo out.
Still very close.
So they've got three heroes to hold the base then.
Rats.
They're going to, I don't think they can save their axe, but they can probably hold tier fours. They use the glyph and the buyback from Phoenix. 7 seconds on Phoenix. They're going to force another fight.
No ultimate from Phoenix for 40 seconds now. He's going to be
gonna
diving
go
through,
anyway.
Burns up onto them, and it's obviously really nice for that. As we say, BKB was popped onto the center. Just
the illusions from Phantom Hunter deep in the base, forcing the backstage.
And now
Pseudo goes in.
There's the BKB with that Witch with the armor. Nice.
He uses the cheese.
Able to keep standing. Gets the stun off onto two. Watson's War trying to go as hardcore as possible. And he gets the kill. Only with an armor. Has got a second available. Is he going to go down? Drop it.
No.
Get bizzled up. Chocolate is going to be dying. Potentially Ghost Center style with been used on him. Bites
he
uses the second.
He goes.
Uses the second. Oh,
it
are
wasn't
you
worth
me?
It.
Ichigo brings two back with an armor. And they are still standing. Gets a triple kill. Watson's War wants to go for more. Wants to find this Lao Wai. Finish off him.
The
That's
Phoenix
gonna be
Sun.
A kill. And it looks like
That's
the
four
Phantom
heroes
going down.
Dead.
Remember, he's got the Aegis, though, so they have got to kill him again. He is going to be trying to double gang around, try and waste their time at the very least. And he is now standing up against the Walter War with the cleave, able to just turn and
he's
fight them.
He's doing more damage. Watson's
is
in serious
Watson
trouble.
Now being
healed
by
Sun
the Phoenix,
though.
And it is just a case of Walter War needs to run away. Lao Wai able to get a kill off. Going back up with the Aegis. He's now unstoppable. He's been used up, Watson's War. It's just down, and this is going to be allowed to
Mute's
do this.
Dead as well.
There's another dieback. 101 seconds. Lao Wai.
Ichigo limps to the fountain, but he can't hold it. 6 seconds. Inferno's going to have his ultimate soon. Maybe he can hold with that. But already back in the base is Element, who didn't die in that fight. So they've got two heroes here. They can get Mega Creeps. This could be the game. We could be going to game five, but they call it.
We're going to the final game.
Oh, dearie me.
Really well played there. Ichigo tried to give it a fight off, but I've got to say, credit where credit's due. Druids, well played.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
You
we
can
have
hear
got
them on their feet. And wow.
We have a fifth game of the Emerged Dota 2 Cup Finals coming up for you shortly. What a fantastic game that was.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was classic Dota. He had one farm team against one incredibly farmed hero. Watson's did his very best, but he couldn't quite bring his team to victory. And that means we have to take a little break now, and we'll be right back with game five.
Stay tuned.
We've had a really good finals so far, guys. I think we've had three very close games live on stage, and two deserving teams about to go at it. The winner of this game does get the 2,000 monies.
Yes, finest monies.
The finest money. Well,
and
the Great British Pound.
Well, yes.
English pounds.
And we will be going into this game shortly.
I'm drinking up close, Eddie.
You're drinking up close. Truly, really bad at this map.
I've gone in the bin.
Hey, you're getting through them, so you are going to be, well, wide-eyed and bushy-tailed for this game, and you're going to be
ready for, to see the casino.
We made it all the way through
survived.
The series.
Yes, we are. It is approaching the fourth hour since we hit the stage this morning. And so everyone's still here. There's more of an audience there. Hello, audience.
Yeah, some of them may be waiting for the League of Legends, but you know, that's fine.
Probably are.
Yeah. It's always good to see some multi-game support come out. Is that right? So looking at the screen now, you can see you and his lot. There's Ichigo's team. They're getting ready into the draft, thinking about what they can go through now. This is all on the line. This last final game, this is going to be quite exciting stuff.
The winner takes it all.
Yeah, this is it. This is what it comes down to. Druid's taking that ban out of the Shadow Fiend again, and Sniper being banned out from Ichigo with the Troll
Warlord. We've seen those three out every game.
You mention it, but it's just, if I didn't see it, I'd be surprised. And let us watch this game now. So, Druids, they've been playing well. That final answer last game, absolutely phenomenal. It couldn't be killed.
Nope. Laoi had a 10 seconds remaining. He had a slow start, but the OD created a lot of space, and he came all the way to victory, as we see Storm Spirit again going after his incredibly influential role in our first two games. So, probably not surprising to see him also removed from the pool.
Yeah, and we're going to be looking at the first pick here for Ichigo. They do go for the Lion, which is that fantastic support. You get the Tranquil out, you just walk around, you get smoked.
I think he's been MVP support of the tournament, honestly. Him or Earthshaker.
I think Earthshaker's had a lot of impact, and we'll see what's coming into this next pick for Druids. Druids, obviously, with their first couple of picks here, they'll be really deciding what sort of start they want into this game. Now, Final Answer worked well from last time. Do you think Ichigo should be banning that out?
Not necessarily. I think their problem was the combination of Phantom Arts and OD more than just the Phantom Arts, because the OD was what was keeping them in the game for that good stretch in the middle, because that last took forever to come online. Mm. It was sort of 40 minutes before he started killing people in large numbers. Although maybe the Empower Jug didn't work.
I think there was a trouble with
it. Just came too late.
With
when
the RP.
Butterfly Heart against... No MKB. There was nothing. I don't think there's anything. Even with Empower, he was missing one in three attacks, right? And that's just not enough damage.
Well, it's a big issue for them to try and get this off, and we'll see what they go for as their first way to pick up. 1 minute 20 left on the clock here. And they go for Centaur again. It's been working. Yep. Why change the winning formula
if it
now?
If it ain't fixed.
Yeah.
Well, in the last two games, they had the Lion on in both. So
it's going to be a change up. A little bit of a mix, seeing as what they'll take now. And Druids, they had to fight back. They did lose the first game. They lost the first game, and it's going to be Lina, probably a support leader. There's a lot of love for the Druids taking that support Lina out.
Yep.
And it was actually copied by Ichigo.
Game three
because of the winner bracket advantage. So we'll be looking at that next pick up.
Seeing some role reversals here. Druids taking one of Ichigo's trademarks. And Ichigo getting the Lion, which has been a key part of the last two victories. It'd be, as you mentioned, it'd be a big comeback if Druids can complete it here with a victory. That's three games in a row after losing
Five
the first, and of course
remaining.
Losing 2-0 to Ichigo yesterday in the winner's bracket. So,
obviously they had a lot to prove.
They had a lot to prove, and they have proved themselves. Even if they failed to win this game, they have come and acquitted themselves better than many expected. And better than many, especially this morning after the dominant performance from Ichigo in the series yesterday.
I think either team here could be very happy with the performance. Obviously, no matter what happens, the person who they want to come for the win, they are hungry for the
win.
But they have been performing very well, both teams, and they have made it to the final so far. So, 1 minute 20 up next on this, and there is the Medusa pickup for Ichigo's team. He is now, thanks Ichigo, man. We're excited to see that schedule. Rest in pieces, we hardly knew.
So, the League of Legends final is going at 2 o'clock, right, guys?
They'll be having a 2 a.m.
We'll see. If you're League of Legends, I suggest you go and get a beer, because you're going to be here until 4 o'clock watching Dota.
Dota dominance coming out here, really established it. We have hijacked the stage for everyone to see.
So, this is another way of dealing with Phantom Lancer, of course, because you don't want to pick a PL into the Juicer.
Well, you say that, but Phantom Lancer gets that Diffusal online, then suddenly Medusa's Mana Shield is...
But then Stone Gaze, of course, you can't run your illusions at her because she melts them all.
True.
It's obviously a more complicated matchup than just Medusa always wins, but it's assuming Medusa is prepared and they don't get the drop in it, it's something that will make Druids think twice before they bring PL back into the pool. Ichigo decided they don't want to see the Anti-Mage that played a big part in the Game 3 victory.
I think Druids may may still be thinking about it though, because again, that feels about.
We're getting rid of the OD too.
OD being banned now.
I think that's a really good play because Chocolat has been an important part of all their games. Even the game they lost, he won his lane. He's played incredibly well this tournament from what I've seen of him anyway. So careful. And now one more ban. They've Druids have got rid of Phoenix, remaining, which has been on Intrigo's team for the last two games.
Yeah, and it mute. 5 seconds remaining. He had a couple of issues. He tried to make some rather large plays. It's the case he tried to go hard, but Druids didn't let him.
Yeah, he didn't have a great game. Yeah, unfortunately for Ichigo. It's a really greedy support, and Ichigo do love to play greedy lineups, but
you give him a greedy support, he normally gets something with it. Yeah. But unfortunately, it's a little bit of a struggle now.
Even the best of us have those days which don't go the best. There's a Earthshaker is taken out. He's been in every game so far this finals. That's the first time he's merited a ban.
Yeah, getting him banned out is probably the wise decision, as they've seen what it could do in their hands. They don't want to give it over to...
Was he banned in game one, too? Maybe I've just lied. I can't remember.
I think maybe game one banned, but I didn't want to be the one to call you out.
That's right. I'm going to look it up on the schedule.
Oh, see, this is the joys professional of having checking this stats back.
Oh, no, it's going to be game one, because they don't know we've waited, do they?
And let's quickly have a look at this next pick up for Druids.
There was no Earthshaker. I lied to you all. I'm sorry.
You are a terrible, terrible person. Ventral Spirit now being picked up for Radiant the Druids. Quite nicely, you get the swap out. You can be taking someone into a sticky situation, or you can be saving one of your heroes.
Also combos nicely with Lina for the early game roam. You know, you've got the instant stun to set up. Boy, they are putting all their eggs into the Medusa basket, Rusts.
I think that's definitely the way they play it. It's definitely the way they enjoy to play it. And it's the way that Ichigo wins games normally. The game goes to at least 60 minutes. Medusa, they go, are you ready? And they're like, no, I need to get at least two more backup rapiers. Then they'll think about going in with a buyback in case things go wrong. Then they can be taking racks. And from there, they can try and make
We've seen some big Medusas this weekend. We've seen
a lot of Medusas.
We've seen, and they're going to counter tiny. It with Tiny. I think that was a reflex. Tiny pick seeing the Wisp. I don't think that was a great call from Druids. I don't think that was ever in Ichigo's mind. They've picked the Bristle back. So Wisp has someone to work with ganking early, but someone who comes online much earlier than Tiny, who does need to pick up some items.
You say that, but Laowei has played...
It's true, they have played it solo.
But this Tiny... Okay, in this series, the Tiny hasn't been that big. I believe it was picked up one of the games. I might have just lied.
It was in game two and it lost.
Game two. Yeah, game two, and it did lose in the game. But... Tiny can make work. We saw it happen against Dress TV yesterday, this morning, and they went in
12
quite
hours
heavy.
Ago.
Yeah, and they are now going to be looking at that last ban up. Well, what would you like to see, man? So they've got their Eye, they've got their Lion. They're looking at.
Both teams have a core left to pick. So it's probably Druids need either a middle or they've printed a middle hero here. And Ichigo would probably need a safe lane. I think will Medusa mid, do you think?
Well, Ichigo has taken Medusa into the mid before. We could see Bristleback and Io just go to
There's a lot of lane setups, I'm sure.
And they could obviously go the like.
What's causing? They're going to get rid of Bat. I think it's the off lane that's yet to be picked. Druids having a. Ichigo's lineup is pretty open ended as to where those cores are going. I think it's a bit clearer for Ichigo as they ban here. Santor's almost certainly going to the offlane. Tiny's almost certainly going safe, and they've got to pick a mid hero. They don't want to see Chocolat take control of.
Yeah, this will be interesting to say the least, because, you could, in theory, obviously, leader core is ridiculously nice, but you probably don't want to send it if they've been running it as a support. Have they run core leader at all this game?
I haven't seen them. But then again, I don't have the leisure of sitting and watching all the games.
No, that's true. I mean, you're a busy man, so you can't be expected to see all of this and know all of this. Queen Pain will be banned.
I think it's going mid. Quap has been a hero they've played. We've seen it played in the safe lane, actually, as well.
It's very nasty against that. Obviously, you could have the Lion back so you could hex as soon as you bring it in. But very nasty against that. The Eye of the Wisp could be
melted.
Blown up.
One scream, and you've got like 200 hit points left out here. Druids then need one hero. Not much time. They've already eaten into their reserve.
Yeah, 2 seconds reserve left, so they are looking at about 13 seconds before moving into that now. And let's see what they go for. The last pick for Druids Esports. This is quite a Druids team, though, I'd say.
This is the aggro sort of thing. They've got two great roaming supports, a offlaner that comes online super early. And, of course, the way they build Tiny, he's also an early game hero. They're going to... Magnus.
Here we go.
Skin of the tea.
The cleave hands. Tiny is going to get that big up.
Oh, so much, man.
Yeah.
Of course, this also offsets the fact that they don't like to build the Aghanim straight away, so he takes a while to get his cleave on. the way Laowai builds Tiny usually anyway. Axe is their last hero. Absolutely fantastic. Wow. And they're going to put Ichigo on the Axe as well. So
Watson Wards
will be playing Medusa.
Okay, Ichigo on the
Axe. I can hear Dreadknight through my noise-cancelling
headphones. You could always...
Oh, it's an Ichigo Axe!
You could always hear Dreadknight there, so shout out to Dreadknight and their team in the
crowd. Third place in our tournament. You'll see them on the stage if you hang around getting some lovely checks.
Yes. Okay, so let's see what happens when we get into this first game. This is Druids Esports v Ichigo Go Go.
This is going to be an exciting game, I think. Druids have drafted a lineup that needs to force team fights, and Ichigo, of course, want to avoid them. They want to get some nice picks with the Axe Wisp in the early part of the game, and then transition into big scary Medusa around 50 minutes in. Will Druids let them? Is the big question. That is the key question as we head into this game. We're waiting for Laowai to pick up his Tiny.
The last game of the series, we are finally starting into it. Ichigo Go Go versus Druids. This is what it all comes down to. We went to the best of five, and let us introduce the team. So, on Ichigo's playing the Axe. He's going to be running around here. Infernokoi playing that Lion. He's played a lot of Lion this tournament. Watson's Water on the Medusa. Going to be taking that mid lane. So, Soodle and Mute will be taking the off as the Bristleback and the Io. Do you want to go for the Diamond?
Indeed. Iceberg is on the Ventral Spirit. Chocolat's playing his Magnus. Laowai on his trademark Tiny. Element is on Lina. And in the bot lane, we have Nyze on Centaur for the third game in a row.
So, okay. Let's see if there's any sort of clash now. Because you remember, like, Phantomancer last time, it was an odd first
blood. Yes, the ridiculous cheese chase that occurred. But it looks like both teams are going to play a bit more passive, of course. If there's any time that your nerves are going to play up on you, it is in Game 5 of the Grand Finals at LAN, with a packed house roaring them on. There's a great turnout here at the Esports stage. It's the first time Insomnia Gaming Festival has had a dedicated stage for Esports at LAN. And it's been a lot of fun to see games on here all through the weekend.
Yeah, first live series
on Castle. And for those of you watching this stream, of course, keep it tuned here for League of Legends, CSGO, and Halo as the day wears on.
The battle begins.
Nice plugs, man.
Plugs.
Yeah.
Plugs for days.
And Chocolate will be grabbing that bounty. He's going to be taking that.
YouTube.com/RustandStuffs.
No comment there. Thank you very much, man. Shameless self promotion yet again. As Luna will take the Bristle back into the offlane. Now, so. Medusa, we expect the long haul, but Druids may not let them. Mm. They may not be able to take it this late.
I think it really is the key question. I mean, Tiny isn't the bad late game hero, but Medusa probably has his number in the late portion of the game. I think the challenge here is can Druids force things in the early portion of this game, as we see lots of support rotation here. Not entirely sure where anyone's going quite yet. We've got solo matchups in all the lanes right now. Let's talk about these solo matchups, I suppose. Who wins Bristleback Tiny?
Well, he's also got these two...
The supports are coming in now, yeah.
He has got these two stutters available. Obviously, Vengeance will probably be standing here trying to zone about whilst the leader just sits back and tries to pull and get the stats going, so...
Axe Centaur is an interesting one in the bot lane. You've got the return versus counter Helix, which passive will do more work. Mm. Return, of course, is less reliant on chance. But I
think the late tier is probably the best thing to get it done. Ichigo just said down his safe.
It's probably just going to be a farm trade, let's be honest. And middle lane, you would expect Medusa to do pretty well against the Magnus, and she seems to be doing that so far.
I say Mag going to be getting that gold foot bottle up eventually, and he's going to come to the rock. There's the stun that could be a stun for Lina, and he doesn't throw it out, but now there's
the
Centaur stomp. He's now going to be running in against Elemen.
The neutral creep, hate him.
Laowai comes in with an avalanche. Soodle's in trouble, tries to finish off a kill. There's Io going to get the auto attack, he's going
to
kill it.
First blood to Elemen.
And now this is going to be more. This is going to be the Io now going down here. Potentially, he does have a 10, but
there's a rotation as well. He's not getting out because Chocolat will cut his escape off. He's going to try and head in the jungle, maybe get the knight. Oh no. Long shockwave.
Chocolat,
it's a 2-for-1 and the first blood to Druids. We said they need to make this game start happening early, and they've taken the first step there in the early going.
So it was a shame that I wasn't able to get the couple more attacks off onto who was it who died again there up
Lina.
Top? It was the leader, yes, the Lina early, because they would have been able to get the first blood beforehand, and that would have been really nice for Soodle. Unfortunately, wasn't
just Soodle. If Soodle just hit level 3-2, he was only just short of it. He would have had a second level in his Bristleback, which would have increased his tank ability nicely as well. Lots of, game of inches, as I said last game. Dota can change on any number of things, but it's all about, not all about the shoulda, coulda, woulda, all about what actually happened. As it happens, Druids are 2 kills to 1 up, including a first blood.
So,
looks like
up top, Lowy could be in trouble. The Bristol Bat will run out soon. We'll just get the kill. They will finish that off.
But they're gonna try
now,
and
now this is going to be smoke broken. Wisp realizes what's happening there. Bristol Bat will still be there.
Great play
from this is huge. Now Lina goes down. Well, he's got a double. Soodle is doing the
great play from Soodle there.
Wow.
Mute had to run for his life, and Soodle still dragged the tether through both heroes.
Yeah.
Of course, nice juke off a stun as well from Mute. All credit to him, but Soodle managing to pick up a nice kill there and a second quick death for Element, who's having a tricky start to this game. And it also killed the Tiny. The advantage picked up from the first blood, nicely offset, and Soodle, this is such a horrible hero to play against in lane, as anyone who's played Dota will tell you. A bully, outright bully this Bristleback.
Bear in mind the two roaming supports, they did smoke up, go towards the mid lane, obviously realised they could come back, go for a kill top, but because of that, Laue was left by himself and did die. As that happened, then the supports tried to go in to finish off the Wisp, and then it all went wrong.
It's exactly what these two need to do. Mute needs to obviously get that quick six, and him and Soodle are going to be buddies for the immediate early part of the game while Axe gets his initial farm. And once Axe has got Blink, you know, you can bring Axe into the jungle to go and find Dunks. It's they have the ability to stall the game. It's not like they're coming in just like praying that Medusa is going to be able to
they
farm
are gonna
quickly enough. They've got lots of tools to force Druids to delay the game as well.
They'll do anything, everything in their power to try and get some medical. We'll throw the Hex out here. Bot does have a stun available. There is going to be a taunt as well. And now this is going to be set up, taking a fair amount of damage. Is still walking away, tries to get a stun off. And
he's going
to
try and
gets the double edge. And now he's still on 6 HP.
Chocolate!
Away! Ichigo, unable to get the kill. Bombs are salving himself. Ichigo now just running. There is going to be bottle charges up to him. There's going to be another shockwave in 2 seconds.
Well.
And now Ichigo gets
nice
the taunt off, which saves him a couple more seconds for shockwave. Is
Inferno
there?
Inferno TPs!
Gets the stun off. Now
yeah.
He's
there we go. What a that was hype.
Four for four. We are now 4 minutes 39 seconds into the game. We talked about Druids being able to make the kills, and you're excited at their own hype there.
Oh, that was some great stuff. Chocolate with a timely rotation for the middle lane. He's trashing Watson's in lane as well. He's had a great series as Chocolate. Full power to the guy. A fantastic mid laner. And here comes Ichigo into the back into the bottom lane straight away. Back onto his farm. He did at least manage to get his team another kill off that. Nice solo XP for Inferno Koi as well, who's on to level 3 thanks to that. In the top lane, Laowai in dire trouble. Soodle doing the dive. Iceberg wants to chase. Chocolate TPs. Soodle's in trouble there. But Mute comes Ham. He turns around. He got blocked by the creeps. He couldn't keep presenting his back. And now Mute's going to die as well. It's a 2-for-1. Well played from Chocolat. Timely TP rotation. I'll just after I talk to him, he backs me up.
Yeah.
What a big play. What a guy. And Iceberg living on a nice amount of HP. Nice amount of HP too. He's 0-0-4. Nice preserving of his own life there on that squishy Vengeful Spirit in the early game.
He wants to try and just big himself up to you, and he TPs in, and because of that, it will lead to a double kill. So obviously, Laowai did die again. 0-2-2, which is an ideal.
Yeah.
He has picked up his boots, and he has picked up a stick as
if
well.
I think they don't have to mind too much, because Watson, he's not doing terribly, but he's not exactly free farming his way to glory. There's enough pressure coming in from Shacklite. He's playing, you know, a solid Magnus. He's already got a bottle and Arcane Boots. That Shockwave spam, really irritating for any hero, never mind a relatively squishy early game Medusa. And of course, they have got support when they need it. More Shockwave spam.
Okay, is walking down bot. They're going to try and find something for the knife.
He's got level 2 of
Pearl. There's
level 6 on Axe.
And
this
is going to be a stun. Where are we getting done?
No, unfortunately,
TP. Has the stick, and now there's going to be a Sappy back.
Oh, he missed the stun.
Gets stunned off, but that's okay. Still got to go down, and he's going
to
be trying to run away now.
His Trunks are going to have a cooldown. This might actually be a kill for Ichigo.
Boom.
No, he's not.
Yeah. He's okay.
His Trunks were on cooldown for longer, but maybe not.
So, Soodle standing up here top has got all the venom as well as his Predator. He's got to be trying to run these fools down. But whether he can get that off, we've got Druids happily standing up against it. They are leading the kills at the moment. 7 kills in this best of 5
round
finals.
Close game. Druids with the early advantage, which is what we'd expect to keep the lineups. Watson's doing his best. I'm not sure if sending to mid lane is the best thing, because we know how great Chocolat is in lane. What do you think? Do you think we would have rather seen him in the safe lane, put Axe mid, maybe just sacrifice the Axe?
Well, I think it's very hard to kill the Centaur down here anyway, and it has been a couple of close attempts. Obviously, if you got like a spin or two earlier, very low HP, and then the Centaur would have had even less, and Ichigo's able to go into this jungle camp now, takes some of the stats. with Wadsworth Farming. I think this is going
okay. Look at his naked inventory, by the way. He's had to dunk a creep. There were not enough spins there, ladies and gentlemen. That's not how you use that ultimate. Don't go in a pub and do it.
Run it back to his.
Yeah, he's got a fountain now. Laowei has popped his first level of growth, finally at level 6. Seedle is doing really well in this lane, though. He has the level advantage, and he's holding even on the CS. Trouble for Mute, though. He's in the danger zone.
We're starting to hit him. Dead hero. Dead hero, I'm afraid. Just walked into the
Shocklight grabbing a haste rune on as well. Inferno Clay heads for the hills as he sees this.
He's trying to sit up, trying to stay mid, trying to get his levels in whilst he can, and then hopefully make something more of it, and there's got to be Rusulak getting that.
The 3-1-0 Santa, by the way, is on course for a Blink Dagger around the 10-minute mark if he keeps playing like this, and there's actually Ichigo could be in trouble here. Stop Double Edge Stampede,
he could just go in for it, it just depends.
He's considering it, but the Tranquil Boots are doing work, he's going to be okay, I think.
TP available from Io at the moment, so this could be a bit
It's on the top lane where they're going, and he's all alone. He gets his back, he's going to try and pull spray.
Tidy takes a lot of damage, unfortunately he had a stick available, he could have like, 5 quills.
No TPs either from his team. Ichigo did have one. But he was actually, the center was there, he would have run in and cancelled, I think.
Yeah, seeing as he was stampeded as well, that was the easy option for him to walk in. But like I said, up top, the Bristlepack is keep getting caught here, but it is three-man stun. You've got Avalanche, you've got the Lightstrike Array, and you've got Vengeance stun.
As we commented, this is, Druids love to try and win the laning phase, and this is just how you do it with the big stuns on your supports to get lots of kills. They've not been as active as some have, though, as I say that, they're going to try and prove me wrong, I think. But they haven't been roaming quite as much. They've been just happily sitting in the top lane. Obviously, they can't leave Laowei alone against Bristleback. Though now Wisp has cleared off to other parts of the map, Seedle can't be quite as aggressive. This is a big wrap.
And will they go for it? It's Watson's Ward. Slivering down the lane.
Watson's is in trouble.
Here we
go.
Has got Stone Gaze.
Look at the TPs.
They are not messing around.
Iceberg's in trouble here.
Nice. Does miss, though, onto him. Will hit the creeps.
Zoning stun, mate. Zoning.
Zoning, yeah. Now we'll see Inferno Quake this part.
Nice. Druid's hiding in the tree line and getting off. Sorry, Iceberg hiding in the tree line.
Yes,
so. Yeah, they forced 3 TPs and Stone Gaze for 1 TP. So, despite the fact they got no kills, Druid's probably happy with that exchange. Shocklap I'm waxing lyrical about this guy, but he's had a great game. There's his 10-minute Blink Dagger, nice and finished. Nyze in the bot lane is about to get his as well, so that's going to be 2 Blinks online up for 11 minutes for Druids.
Yeah,
there's the Blink on the Sentinel. Any TPs, they're going to try and make a go with it.
Axe will get his out now, though, so Axe will be ready to go in. And as everyone knows, with Axe, this Torn Berserker's cool. This is that. Oh, okay, there is a Invis onto Io, so although it doesn't look invisible, Io can't.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
If I was a hero, an entity made up entirely of particle effects that aren't affected by the Invis rune, so GG Valve.
Pretty neato. So looking in the mid lane, Magnus is going to be trying to get his level up.
Do you think Laowei still going to go for a Midas?
I think he's going to go
straight Blink.
His Blink out now because he could have just kept his boots and then had that glove pace and get it to Midas. But I think they really want to get the Blinks now. They've got Centaur with the Blink Dagger and they could be a potential.
They've got Centaur and Magnus with Blinks.
Dire's
bottom tower is under attack.
For some data,
We can't be, obviously, with some of the potential patches, you can't be too obvious because of those.
Yes, we do not have a sound booth here at the Insomnia Esports stage.
But still, it's fine, makes it a bit more interesting for Kakashi. You know, sometimes I get to see stuff like more Dota 2 being seen on the screen.
Oh, I love Dota 2.
Yeah. And there is one of these perks as well. Out.
Oh, what an item.
Really. And Seedle will be continuing to
farm. Looks like Seedle's heading towards a sand. Probably going to go ahead for the Heaven Talbot later in the game. It's useful against the big auto attacking Tiny.
Inferno will grab out some more wards and sentries and will be running through the middle. Gets the sentry down and will spot out that ward.
Watson's water looks like he's going to head for Yasha. Into, I would imagine, Lincoln's Sphere is the standard build on this hero, this land, it seems.
I think getting that Yasha getting a Scaddy outright.
So, yeah, I think.
Obviously, there is some.
I think every time I've seen Watson's play, he's got Lincoln's.
Well, we'll see what they
see.
I do agree with the Lincoln's being quite nice. Obviously, you've got like the good way and stuff, and swap would be pretty nice to see coming out.
And
Chigo has to hide. He's hiding in the trees.
Blink dagger out now there. So.
So that's three blinks up for druids now. They have great mobility. It looks like probably a Yule's Rota on the Lina coming up next.
Yeah.
And good old Venge just buying smokes and wards.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Thank you, announcer lady. Yeah. I've not heard her in ages. Did we turn her off?
I have no idea, because that actually Radiant's really confused me. Because now that I'm hearing the announcer, which hasn't been on all the time, but she is very keen. So, okay, so the announcer is helping us to cast.
Now,
yeah, that's fine. And there's now going to be a snake flying out onto the Magnus. So, a little bit there. And they are going to try and maybe take this tower top with Sudo continuing to fly away.
Checking the net worth to not to blow Shoplet's trumpet anymore, but he's 1500 gold ahead of everyone. But
you are the king of his fan club, aren't you?
Yeah, I apparently am. Can't help it. Someone plays well.
No. I was going
to
say.
Watson's is starting to rack up his farm. As we saw last game with his Juggernaut, a slow start followed by a rapid acceleration of farms.
Moving now used down bot. There's going to be that catch.
Wow.
And yeah, Axe just goes down.
Goodbye.
Had enough for you.
TP's having cancelled. Oh, here we go. Here, this is going to be the RP coming in. Chocolate catch the IO and the Bristleback getting out here. There's now the Avalanche. Doodle goes down, and they came into this fight. Suddenly, it all goes wrong. Apologies for the camera there. Not sure what happened, but there's a pretty good one there.
Excellent play from Druids. I don't know if you heard on Avalanche, but there was a big shout as soon as they saw there was PT.
Yeah.
They're coming, stun here. And they applied. Excellent. Excellent execution from Druids, and they get three kills for no return. And they are going to start opening up the lead they need to win this game before Medusa becomes a relevant factor.
Now, this is going to be the issue. If Druids keep their momentum like this, able to take the tier 1s, tier 2s. Okay, that's the first tower.
That's the first tower. It's not as
40 minutes this, in.
This Ichigo will be happy with that. And as I just said about Watson, he's starting to pick up his farm rate. He's got his first item of note in the Asha. We'll see what he goes for next. We had an argument over what we thought he'd get.
Yeah.
So now, Scardy or Lincolns is the consensus. Putting against something else, now they both look like idiots.
I know. Yeah, that's also
how it works.
The castles can't be like that, especially when it's us. And Laowei has got that big
brigade.
Brigade is actually a good term, but and there will be shortwaves flying out from towards mid.
There's a few. Check the
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Pinged.
There is a big amount of farm there for somebody when they want to turn.
Axe will not get the torn off.
Now
the stampede gets the stomp off, and this could be a double edge against tossed up. It's now going to be
the big
whiz.
Save from you.
2-4-2 able
and Sudo's going ham.
Should maybe not be going this hardcore because he's now going to have to try and run, and they will be able to do so. The toss does come back out.
Fenrir's got mana for the thing. He lives. And then they come back in. Axe.
No,
he
in.
Misses the jump!
No!
Double spin!
This is absolutely massive. Io will now go down, and this is a 2-for-2 exchange.
So
they will be piling weight, and Ichigo
they
could
got
still
to,
go
but
for
it,
a torn here.
It's a train they've won, because they've got the Tony, the centaur for the Wisp, who's already got 6 and therefore doesn't need any more levels, and the Bristleback. It's a win for Ichigo. Great, great play from Mute to save Ichigo's life there. That was vital to them turning that fight.
Sudol stayed up long enough, just clearing through.
He kept them on site.
Exactly.
They didn't retreat, and they didn't leave their characters right. They could have got another kill, but fortunately, Lion ran out of mana before he hit his finger off.
Yeah.
So
Venge actually stood pretty close to the axe, obviously sight lines in the trees.
I mean, despite Ichigo flubbing his dunk, he got a really great spin, which killed two heroes.
Yes. Recovery spin.
Recovery spin is fine. You see the Yule Scepter picked up by. Element on his Lina, so he can now do the stun combo. Nobody with a BKB yet, so there's no way out of it unless you have really clipped fingers, and he slightly messes the stun combo.
Obviously, with blink fingers, let's see if Magnus can make any more RPs to this huge threat. He is level 12 at the moment. He has got that blink, has got that full stuff. Let's quickly go through items and check out what's going on here. Lion, check his current gold. He's in 198, so he's a bit poor at the moment, but what's coming out on the Kara? We will see.
The Sanj finished on Bristleback. He's stacking the main chance with his goo, etc., and the other venom. If you get beaten up by the Bristleback, basically you're going to walk really slowly, and that will give his opponents a chance to get in. Now we've been talking about this farm, and Magnus is doing fantastically, of course, but Tiny is actually struggling. He's finished his blink, but he's not actually got anything on top of that yet. We're 18 minutes in, and he's a long way behind his opposite number. You know, he needs to match Watson's water. Watson's is the problem. Watson's just sitting with 2,000 gold in his hero. Looks Looks, he's going to get an ultimate orb. It just doesn't tell us anything about what he's building next.
So the Radiant Crown of Karin, everyone. There's obviously a build work towards this slab, which that's going to be good for this. And they are going to be clearing it out.
Oh,
and
now
go down
bot.
There you go. They are
coming
in.
He went a bit early there.
But
he's
fine.
In trouble.
Look
he can
happened.
Turn. He's going
to
turn it.
The torn off this
Here comes
potential.
The TP.
And there's your TP. But the RP is there. Catches him again. And this is just a repeat of what's happened. History is just keeping beating himself. Sudo tries to get at least another kill, and there's two people so low. That was about 5 HP there.
There were no dunks again from Ichigo. He's not.
Yeah.
He's just not delivering dunks around the crowd. He didn't use it that time. He was running around the fight trying to get close enough
Radiant
to finish off
there
the
There was a swap back to...
it was good play. Middle tower is under attack. Just not being able to deliver the requisite dunks. The ultimate orb is picked
Dire's
up on
structures
the
pizza. Are fortified.
Can you stop scrubbing
Radiant's
on the map,
top
soon? That's really BM.
No, he might be just scrubbing
Dire's
on the map. He says no, he's
on
sleep.
He can circle
but,
things,
yeah.
That's fine.
Radiant structures
and then it's going to be Magnus. That shows you how much they can be hearing.
Livid.
But yeah, 7 for 17 at the moment. And let's quickly have a look at the graphs. It is now over towards 5k
Radiant's
gold.
Top tower
XP
is
just about
the gank train for Druids is starting to get Tiny back on track. He's going to go for the Acceptor next.
He's got the axe, goes to the blink, and
nice
able to get this out.
Yeah.
So, 4 stuff back. Blink 4 stuff, the blue really is really there, and they are going to try and make plays. So, what can they do here?
A brief lull in proceedings, though. Everybody heading towards the middle lane. Again, it's a party in the middle lane.
Well, everyone's invited to this pie, and there's going to be more stuff.
Axe picking up an Ogre Club. I think it's BKB. I mean, Aghanim Scepter Axe is a thing, though one we've not been seeing much recently.
Probably going to need that BKB. As we said before, the spells are coming out. Obviously, this is the support here, so there's not going to be the Aghanim's out yet. But saying that, there has been a lot of kills. 5-2-6 on Aghanim at the moment. He's able to get more and more, and this could be nice. Obviously, they're going to be farming up here at the Ancients, and there's potential for...
Shout out to Iceberg for the 1-0-11 support game. It's always nice to see.
Hasn't been taken down yet, and there's going to be more stuff being delivered. That way, good towards the Aghanim's, and there's now the Cleavehands given just as the... just as the agents will die. But hey, just fine. Step it up,
Shockley.
Whoa, that is very...
This guy with 9 point, the most worth on the map. He's got to flame this somehow.
So you're just going to be pushing. I'm going to get this tower now. And
Element lingering in the top lane. They're going to have a TP coming from the Centaur. Flicks back, though. Looks like a...
That is true for more. Going for it.
Looks like Steve is getting distracted. He's got a Vitality Booster. I think we're going to see the Crimson Guard. That new item. Still a new item, I know it's like a year old now.
Yeah, well, they could be getting this out, but I think this is okay cause is just to get the casual Vanguard and then maybe just try and push this SOI, get some items there. And look at the scores.
I think it won't be Heaven Talbot.
It could be a Heaven Talbot. Obviously, very nice against the Tiny when he gets this Aghanim's, but at the moment he's kind of just the spell nuke.
He's also got the Cleavehands, though.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Speaking of Cleavehands, there's a Cleavehands party.
Tower. Got to be going down. Aghanim's will get the last hit.
Snipes it with his 94 damage Lina. Well played.
And there's now going to be the Magnus just grabbing
Dire's
that.
Bottom tower
again, just drawing attention
attack.
To Watson's chocolate cheese on top of him for now, but the farm continues to ratchet
Medusa,
up.
Medusa, yeah. We are 21 minutes into the game. Has got that ultimate orb.
Of course, the thing with Medusa is unlike every other hard carry in the game, pretty much, he does need 40 minutes to get all the items he needs to have big effects in fights. He can start turning up, maybe.
Yeah, well, saying that, obviously, Ichigo do have the axe and the bristle back with Io, so you'd think that they'd be able to get more. And that does show the 7 kills. Unfortunately, there has been plenty of catches. Two now here trying to defend up top this tower.
He's got support in the trees, too. This Blink Dagger axe can come in from nowhere.
But it looks like they're not going to be worried about it.
It's just easier. They're going to try and hold the tower for a bit longer. They're going to get it deny range if this catapult hits it two more times. It won't, though. It's a shame. Just above deny range on the tower.
So,
Watson's is going to go for the Skadi, so congratulations on being cleverer than me.
I am the greatest.
You are the greatest.
Yeah.
YouTube.com/Russ and stuff.
How many times is that now? Twice?
Twice.
Well, just in this game alone. But yeah, okay.
I've been really well behaved. It's the first time I've been. Nice deny from
Sue. Yeah, Sue able to get the deny off and back it out. Nicely done there. Just Dire's middle tower not really that cheeky either, because Tidy could have blinked it and tried to stop it, but just lets him go.
One of the multitude of blink heroes hanging around. Old swap.
Sentries. Around there, just making sure
they're guarding their Medusa's farm. It's vital to their game's plan, of course. It's another game of 4 Protect Watsons. Unlike last game, where it sort of morphed into it after Ichigo had such a miserable laning phase on the Magnus, this game they came out with a plan where they need Watson's Water to accrue a lot of farm, put the team on his back, and bring them over the line to win this LAN. And he's going to have that Eye of Skadi increasingly soon.
Some rotations out here. So Druid's kind of owning the Radiant jungle at the moment as well, just moving through, clearing out what he can. There is going to be a Haste Boiled out here on the Magnus, and they are going to move around, see what they can catch out. And there's going to be some more.
Ichigo's nearly picking up this BKB, which would be great for him if he could just run around and wreak havoc in the fights without having to worry about the multitude of stuns. Again, I point out the Druids have a stun on every hero they brought to this game. It's their chosen style of play, and Ichigo with the counter to such style of play by building something that stops you stunning them, stops them stunning you. Words are hard.
Very hard. Actually, exceptionally hard. But that's
it looks quickly. Like it is going to be Sanction Yasha on Bristleback. Yep. Next.
And it's so nice, because you talk about Bristleback, you talk about the fact that you can be kited. Sanjin Asher at least helps alliviate some of these issues. There's going to be some of this.
You get the Sanj first, you have the initial the Maul chance, which can help in the earlier portion of the game. And then you get the Sanjin Asher. It also tanks you up too. Nice little buff from all the agility you're building.
And there's now going to be a bit of farming going on around the map.
Farm. It's of course exactly what Ichigo's team wants. They've held pretty good map control. They have lost their tier 1s, but the tier 2s all still stand, all on full HP as well. So they've got plenty of positive ones as they do finish. Laowai cutting it precious close there. Only 200 hit points left, but you know, it's all you need. He's also finished his tree with that frag. As at the exact same time, Medusa finishes her Eye of Skadi. Will we see her go back for the Manta now, do you think?
Well, obviously the mana dodge potential is really nice, depending on how quick Watson's water is feeling, and there's a lot.
Everything can be dodged by Manta if you play it right in this game. I think it will be a good item. Of course, it still lets you split push and hold your base more easily as they get some chip onto the top tower. That's top tier two.
Chocolate will just be continuing to.
Chocolat's picked up the BKB himself.
Yeah, 10-second BKB now.
It's helpful against, Lion, but they have a lot of disable that goes through it. You know, you can't. Stone Gaze works through it, and so does Call, and of course Cunning Blade if they can do enough damage. So middle tower is under I doubt it will be the focus of most of the fights, but it's not a free pass now. Duty likes as Laowai denies the tier 1 mid.
Tower now just to deny, which is fine. They were able to get that off, and that is going to be this.
Of course, the siege damage from that tree will let them start to push the issue now, try and limit Watson's farming area.
Here you go. Oh, blinks away there as soon as the Sabo comes out. There's going to be now the avalanche. He still gets to go out as a toss. He pops BKB, gets the taunt off, still standing for a while longer, and now he's going to be running all the TP. And now Medusa turns up. There's going to be a missile stone gaze because Element does come and use the yours. Now Sentai's been focused down. The good ability has been used, and there's the Lion Stun comes in, and we see Chocolat
coming back. Now he's coming back.
Oh, this is an issue now. Wisp
didn't get the kill. Big Hex. Inferno Koi saves his life in the bat lines. Watson's Water is doing work on everybody else. Soodle brings down Element.
And
Iceberg tries to TP. He's dead.
And this is big for Ichigo. We have seen Laowai running away, and Chocolat is running on one side.
We talked about the coming online of Medusa, and you sort of saw that in that fight. This guy doing work, but Soodle is the man with the plan. He goes in. They didn't hit him. The cool sprays kept coming out. Oh, and he's so tanky now. They don't want to hit him.
So it seems like there was quite a bit of cheering there when there was a crowd fight going on there. A crowd fight? A crowd fight. There's no fights in the crowds here, but there might be at the end of the game, I suppose.
Dread Knight might start putting people in the bin, you never know.
Yeah, also true.
Medusa has... he's overtaken Chocolat on the net worth now. That was a big fight, actually. If they won that fight, they were going to lose a tier 2, at least one tier 2, maybe two. But as it stands, I called the BKB somewhat questionable before the fight.
I think,
And it was absolutely... I take it back. Ichigo's a genius.
Ichigo played
and
that well.
They turned the fight around. Big plays from Soodle and Watson's Water and Inferno Koi saving Mute's life to make sure nobody on his team died.
I'm not sure, thinking back about it, I'm not sure too much how that team play went down, but... Wasn't there a stomp about to come out from the center as the BKB happened, and there was a toss in the air which allowed it to get off? Because if so, maybe there was a chance for the stun to be, constant. But hey, maybe it's one of those moments
Laowai
where they just.
Laowai didn't expend the Aegis in that fight, by the way. He maybe could have stayed in a bit longer.
Well, the trouble is, if he died at the very end, which obviously when he was running,
he has blink. He could have fast fingered the blink. They don't have any stun that could wait for him. Unless the timing on the. Call is impeccable. He would have seconds to double press blink to safety.
But then saying that, the axe could obviously run after blink as well. And this is that tiny with that empower just on the hunt. He's after you. Check the sightlines. We can see that Radiant. They get an idea of what's going on here, and they are now going to be just trying to take this tower bot.
Druids, yeah, they can't stop forcing the issue, though. Despite that loss, they still have a lead in this game, and they can't let it slip completely. So they're going to keep doing their thing while there are some cooldowns still on for Ichigo. And being in a position, they do pick the first tier two of the game up. So it's a nice injection of gold, so they can try and keep their snowball rolling.
And lots of pings out from Soodle.
Soodle is livid about something.
Pinging out of control, and there's now going to be that Manta for Medusa. 28 minutes into the game, this is our last game of the best of five. Everything to play for, Ichigo Go Go versus Druids.
Druids Ozone, just shout out their title sponsor, because they haven't done that all series, we're bad people.
To be fair, I say what I see.
I say druids,
but yeah, that in the mid lane, we'll see Tai still clubbing away. This could be a chance for them to just take the tower and just not worry too much about it. Centaur is standing on the side, not being hit by the whisper, so he's not blinked, it's not going to be turned off.
See, this is what you talk about, the siege damage is excellent for this team. In the top lane though, Watsons and Soodle are trying their best to get a trade. They're not going to get it though, they're going to have to back off, they're going to get a bit more chip, but they're going to have to tree and TP themselves to safety as in comes Centaur looking for a pick maybe, not presenting themselves. Stealing the Ancients to his Lar White. The Aegis is gone, and we have the Roche respawn.
Yeah,
it's a pretty long one.
And we'll have a look at the urn flying out to Iceberg. So, checking out the score quickly, we can have a look and see that Magma still hasn't died in these exchanges. Chocolat.
Neither has Watson's, though, which is more important at this point.
That
I think.
Is true. Obviously, he's had less kill contribution, but still staying at top of the last hits.
All the money you can make with that split shot. 220 last hits, 30 minutes. Not the most ridiculous tally we've seen in this tournament.
No, but
I believe there was a game where Gronis had 800 last hits earlier in proceedings. That was silly.
Are you trying to tell me that someone like Gronis farts?
Someone like Gronis farts.
Absolutely insane. And we will see Tiny with the Empower hands.
I think Gronis still lost, though. Team was too heavy.
Don't call our players teams. Like, they're literally in the audience. You could be getting in trouble now.
Am I going back in the bin?
Yeah, well,
anyway.
There's going to be a tier 2 being focused. And now is there the blink forward, but the BKB was there from Ichigo, and they are torn it
no
up. And now
him.
He's got to be walking back. He does have the center on the sideline. They're just waiting
big
for this
TP
BKB.
Big TP forward from Soodle, and they have to run. They're scared of Soodle.
Unfortunately,
we were talking about how we didn't think Elements was going to get an axe, but he's actually minted.
Well,
that is an
ag
inside. This Venge is just playing the hardest sacrifice. He's got a Medallion of Courage, an urn, and consumables in his inventory, and brown boots. So Iceberg playing the hard sacrifice to let his teammate get some items and start being effective, but that means the BKBs, no one is safe from the scary Laguna Blade. Infernokoi doing the same thing for Mute, but Mute not quite having the same amount of money on him. He's unfortunately died six times.
Heaven's Harbor going to come out for Centaur, which is really nice against Medusa. Also, having that disarm just being able to come out. Speaking of Centaur, he flicks it, four stuff.
Double
edge, but now this is going to be a taunt. They're going to try and focus him up, and I think this is a case of leave Centaur to die.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant tool from Ichigo, saving his support's life.
Get a run out by Soodle, throws the stun out. Nice dodge from Soodle, going in for more. Element gets swapped back.
Lightning.
The Vinibrain has been used, and Medusa just standing there, going to refine them. Iceberg now trying to focus up against you, but he goes down. Soodle's still just running around. He's like, go on then, you want some. Let's see what we get. Goes in, unfortunately, that's
Iceberg
all
giving
out.
His life so his core could live exactly what you want from your vengeful spirit. Mute's 242-esque. In his sacrifice there. But it's going to be a tier 2 off that pair of kills for Ichigo. And this game is looking like it's moving into that. They're at deficit on the scoreboard in terms of gold and not in XP. They're well ahead in XP.
XP, yeah, look at that.
But this where the gold is, and all of it's on this terrifying Medusa.
Tier 2 does go down. They never did utilize the Aegis, but hey, sometimes that's
alright.
Yeah, sometimes it's better to, rather than go ludicrous and then just die twice, it's better to just say, okay, the Aegis has been down. There's now going to be Heaven's Halberd out onto the Centaur. So, we said about this before, would the disarm have helped them a lot this time? I don't know. Let's have a quick check and see what comes out. And you guys can see what's going on there.
See the thing.
So you're going to continue firing up. Want to see that BKB out now? Hold that thought. They are going to bring him back in. Ichigo getting focused up now. It did have his BKB. Will still pop it. And I'm afraid he will be getting slid on the taunt. Gives him some extra armor. Will he be able to get the blink gag off? Unfortunately, a swap back. Now Zipping's forward. And it doesn't matter.
I think he was still looking down
here
to blink.
Yeah, maybe if he turned the blink there, but that would have been.
He could have delayed the death a bit longer. He wasn't getting away. But
no, true.
They had him completely boxed in.
He has some exceptional juking past the Ancients, but
yep.
Hey. BKB is on 7 seconds now, but He tried to get away. Unfortunately, the initial stun came out, so he wasn't able to BKB that. Although he did dodge it earlier.
So they're going to try and take this advantage into a set of barracks.
There is an Eagle Song up on the producer, but there is going to be no buyback on the producer. Quickly checking buybacks. The people who can buyback is the Axe, Magnus, Bristleback, and Iron.
Medusa's taken the trade at the top lane. He takes the last tier two. No, there's two tier twos left on the map now. Unfortunately, the boss has not respawned yet. Do they know that? Well, they're going to get your own check. So they can't take that, and they do end up giving up on attempting to push the high ground. Everyone back. Medusa farming the enemy jungle on his way towards his own ancients.
Just wants to get that extra gold in, just so that if worst thing's worst and he does get caught, he'll be able to
buy it
back in and then go for a fight. If he gets caught, our Stogaze is down. We're not sure if they can go for much.
Ichigo's new adventure is towards the Aghanim Scepter. He picks up the point booster. So we'll see that Carl being put on the time cooldown. So should he flub anymore, he will still have the ability to cast it again. Not seen many big dogs this game. It's a very satisfying skill to call. It's a bit frustrating.
No, yeah, I know. Yeah. You want to just be shouting as the heads are getting slammed in. But it doesn't seem that we've seen it at the moment. There will be a Assault Crest be built up on Laue shortly, but he's still farming away.
I think it's safe to say there's some pretty big fights still to come in this game. There is an advantage being taken out for Ichigo at the moment, we'd say, but Druid's far from out of this. Big shout out to their sponsors, by the way, who did pay for all the travel and tickets to get to this LAN. It can't be overstated how cool that is. Thank you, sponsors, for supporting our esports.
Yeah, supporting the scene. And seeing this,
that
they made it.
Scene.
Well, seeing that, obviously, they made it to the finals, clearly. Well worth it. They're playing up against Ichigo now, and they are going to be looking to make this play. Medusa is farming with 34 minutes of the game, 12 to 19. Looking at the graphs, the gold graph, 2,500 difference in the way of Druids. And look at the XP.
4,500. Oh dear. Words are hard.
Still are, and there's a lot of things coming up for the enemy tier, but Ellen's still sound bad. Not quite level 16 now, and there is a little bit of that going on, and we'll check what happens with Ichigo over here. 2k gold onto him. Wants to build that Aghanim's out right now, and then, hey, if he could start throwing out the dogs a bit early, he's level 16, it would be a shame if we don't see that good raid, but Tiny will pick up the Aegis.
Yep.
Nice. It feels like Magnus isn't getting that opportunity, especially coming up against the high ground to go for that big RP.
Yeah, we haven't seen any. We've seen some counter relocates, but now we've moved to the point in the game where the relocate gank isn't the main reason Wisp exists. Wisp exists to give Medusa more mana and, you know,
and keep the Bristle back alive as well.
Yeah, where necessary. He's not there primarily. His relocates are used to save lives, not to.
Exactly, not to make plays, especially as Druids are moving around this one unit, all with their blink daggers looking to get the kills.
Ichigo is going to be able to get out from the top lane, though, despite being chased down by
BKB now delivered to Laue. He does have that Aegis onto him as well. This is going to be a fresh 10-second BKB, naturally, and they will go for more players. Io, do you want to see him build up a BKB as well? Do you want to see him maybe get a Heaven's Harbor for this Tiny? I think you'll need to get a BKB if you want to.
I mean, Heaven's Harbor would be nice. It looks like Toodles has got the money for his. He's just trying to wait till he has buyback to a blink dagger too. This lean is actually really farmed. He's got more money than the position 3 hero on Ichigo's team. Once again, that's just the difference in farm priority. They've given all of their gold, as much as they possibly can, to Watson's so he can compete to the best of his ability.
Well, let's see what they can get done here. There is a potential to try and force down this tower. They know they've got the siege.
Watson's is in position to trade. Yeah,
and this is going to be what keeps happening. He's like, well, I'm going to be getting more items. He can get the butterfly, but obviously he wants to be increased.
He's
that,
also getting
buyback,
more XP. Doesn't look like he's going to try and push his luck though. They just get the tower for free. There's going to be some shit from the creep wave, but nothing Dyer's of great note on that tower.
Druids.
They have got this Aegis on Tiny. They're gonna use it to get on the high ground.
I want to see if Laue wants to go quite deep here, because obviously if the flight goes a bit poorly, he could be getting stuck and his team forced back, then this could be a troubling play.
Watson's is back in situ to help defend.
Yeah, this could be... This
arrows
could be
being
good.
Drawn on the map, showing us all where Druids plan to go next.
And they are just going to be taking this jungle, farming it up, and just trying to keep that gold flowing towards their pocket. Checking out the buyback status, I believe everyone can. Actually, well, there's no buyback on the Lina because gold, same with the supports. But that's to be expected, really, because obviously they're constantly buying out wards and smokes. So
we are ticking on towards hour five of this this series.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, it's still not the longest one we've had all weekend.
No, that's true. Hey, yeah, exactly. This none is a game, walk in the park,
none of
man.
These games have lasted longer than 60 minutes so yeah. far. I mean, I've just jinxed it. This has got Medusa in it. We're going to be here.
Yeah. Saying that was a rookie mistake, but that's fine. That's
why we're just here to ruin the schedule for everyone else now.
Yeah, shout out to the League of Legends casters.
Yeah, they came and asked us when they'd start before yeah. this game.
I said, well, I can't even remember what I said now, but
probably
yeah.
said soon, because all the games have been quick, and then they got Medusa. Peaking Medusa, she just finished Butterfly, which is a good choice in this game. MKB, not an item you often see getting picked up by Tinies, but now Laowai. Of course, he can use his cleave to get it anyway, hitting another hero and letting the cleave damage the Medusa. There's no evasion against cleave damage in Dota, of course.
3-0-2 Islands of Medusa now, but we talk about it, and Medusa's going to be careful. 2,250 gold suitors. We'll get the kills out there. There's been an avalanche thrown out, and Medusa just getting that damage throw. There's now a spawn. He's been four star back in. And now Laowai gets focused down. That's your Aegis down.
That was Max four star.
Yeah, oh, okay. That was a case of turn around. And now Laowai will be able to back out. There is a Battle Hunger out onto the Centaur, which is nice. Now gets a two man taunt. There's the swap back. He wants to get the RP. He only catches one. He missed one. Who's done Stone Gaze? Turns the Tiny to stone, and there is going to be focused down on the Tiny. The great hit to me still gets the kill. Bristleback goes down. The snake is slivering. There was a stun which does connect on
nice.
Fire, but now another taunt. Aegis goes going so hardcore, and he knows the score. Wants to try and finish up Iceberg. They are going to go for this. Dunk. It's another dunk. They are holding Bristleback, being the meaty wall that keeps their base standing.
3-4-1. They get the carry and two supports just for their offlane. Well, I guess he was actually their role too, isn't he?
Mm.
Well played.
So 3-1. That was with an Aegis, may I add.
Mm.
They can hold.
Effectively 4-1. You worry for Druids, don't you? They're reaching that point where they just can't fight the Medusa. She has too many items. They can't kill her. They don't have the money to just pick up MKBs and deal with her. It looks like she's going to head towards the AC next to get even tankier.
I got to say, Chocolat did obviously try it. Yeah, Blixit tries to get that
RP. He got it on one hero, but it didn't matter.
Stone Gaze, man.
Yeah.
Really, really awkward for them to try and fight against. You got the Stone Gaze there, and it's really... It's unfortunate, because it felt like he had to go because the Medusa was just running around, and it's just, you can't argue it's a misplay from him. It's more that Ichigo are playing well with keeping their team back, they're just being able to focus down the correct people, and just being able to send...
Yeah, they need to get more things. They've got one Heaven Talbot to stop her attacking, but they need a Hex somewhere. There's no one really with the money or the inclination to pick it up. Maybe Magnus can get one instead of something like a Refresher Orb, which I assume he's going to go Refresher. He ignores that advice. I guess it serves the same sort of purpose. Shiva's Guard is the choice from Nyes on his. They're dropping buybacks, by the way. They need these items to fight. It's the right call because they're just going to die.
Mains are pushed out as well, but obviously that isn't really something you could take into account when they could be going for more. And it looks like we'll see once more picking up that Shiva's. He is a big fan of this. I'd normally see him get this as third, fourth item. And it's very, very nice. It gives you that extra armor, the active, and the mana pool. Yeah. It's really.
You sure, quite... sure it's a Shiva's? It could be an AC, maybe?
It could be
an
well,
okay, well, you've watched more of what
I was going to say. I've seen it play a couple times, and it feels like it. Well, they could probably give the AC to a Bristleback, is what I would say, if they were going to go that way. But I may be wrong. I've been wrong about at least one thing in the past, and they are good at outing.
Bristleback's still building towards that BKB. He died in that fight before he got most of the gold. So, excuse BKB. Is that.
So that is a.
Wow, why is off the bin after a casual high ground BKB?
There's now going to be some delivery out here. AC coming out, and there's the refreshers.
It's so not all of it, is it?
No,
he's not got. Oh, it is.
Laowai has got it because he's got the.
Chocolat has a full refresher orb. That's. Ichigo, if Ichigo made the mistake of clumping together, that's potentially a full.
I've got to
say, what is it, 7 seconds old of lockdown? It's ridiculous. Yeah.
Although there was this mistake being used. Oh, here we go. Ooh. Up here. He's so low from Jonas Sedar. Now going to be potentially forward. Gets the stomp and pulls the stab.
The snake
is still coming for you. 76 seconds. No buyback. This could be an opening. They're trying to get this. That is a good snaky sliver. That. Yeah. You took my turn to fall there. I don't know what's going on. So yeah, Centaur was quite low for the jungling, comes out here, and now
it looks like they've only got one choice for objective right now with the with Roshan still being down.
Bear in mind, we said about Ichigo trying to hold, trying to extend on as long as possible, and then we see that they're thinking, okay, well
they've
we can go for this.
They've just got so much farm on Watson's. He's 300 on creeps, 5-0-4, not died yet. Got some killstreak gold earlier in the game too, and they're going to punch the buildings. Here we go.
Tower being sieged down. They will get up. There's now the individuals onto the axe. Axe going to get hit by the stun, and the...
He's just letting it mind. If they want someone to get hit by all the spells, he's the one, though. I mean, him and Bristle about there to take the damage from Medusa.
Yeah, that is the
Medusa's just walking onto the high ground and hitting buildings.
Does Stonegate pull further in?
There's an RP to follow.
Stonegate's now activated. There's going to be a taunt bringing that Magnus back into it. It's going to be, it means that he's turned to stone. Can still be focused up. There's going to be a dunk opportunity. Unfortunately, not able to get it up because he goes back. But now there's the finger back onto Tidy, and this is going to be once more with absolutely no mana. He will have his buyback if he does go down here. But as this happens, it's going to be a swap in. And now we see issues coming down. The Venge does die and still standing. Laue, who has to be, he throws the Bristle further into it. He's like, get out of my base. And they are trying to hold him back. Now Tidy goes forward. Infernoid gets the staff onto Laue, and Suda comes in. But now there's the counter RP from Chocolate. And this could be where it all comes down to. There's going to be a refresher if they need it.
They
that's going to be a kill. And that is three people dead. Buybacks available, apart from one Lion.
Well, they held the base, but at the cost of a range. The melee axe in the middle lane. It's the first racks of the game, and it does go Ichigo's way, and that's really not what you want with the Medusa on your side. The lanes are going to push against you naturally because of that hero. And, well, it looks like they know they have to go now. They're going to force the buybacks at the very least. They're plowing down the middle lane.
Can I just say, Watson's Water did not die in that fight.
No,
had
no
mana on him, and was able to just get away. Good use of the supports there. We will see a buyback from the Wiz. There could be a buyback from the Prism, but maybe they're just going to be heading back from that, and there will be
Unfortunately, it's just the wrong time as well, because the Rish is not up yet, so they can't just retreat and grab that objective on the way out. They're going to go and check, but they're going to be sadly disappointed, I believe. There's a regen rune there.
Right,
exciting. So wraps that up. They're gonna see it's not up.
Yep.
That's a blow
and
for Drill.
And they'll be going over here. A full sub now up onto the Lion as well. And this is quite important. So let us check current gold. So 4,400 gold onto the Medusa. Medusa has got the Blameless Seal, and we will see this happening at some point shortly. Axe has got plenty of gold onto him as well, and he, let me just check, he did buy his Aghanims. Yeah, has got the Aghanims on him. Let's actually go over all the items in case I see something I missed. Brisbane now gets that BKB up. Io still sitting with the same items as earlier, and it looks like most heroes just getting ready to go, and they will now be moving around. So, Maui and Co just farming up. After a fight like that, what do you think the Druids are trying to think of now? They realize they can hold the base, but they did lose objectives. And bear in mind, Ichigo are happy to extend this.
Yes. I don't know what they think. They need amazing teamfight execution, and they need buybacks not to be up. But I don't think there'll ever be a point in this game where Medusa's buyback isn't up, at least.
Mm.
It's a dangerous situation for them. They need more lockdown for Medusa. They need to start buying some hexes. They need to make her incredibly sad.
The trouble is, you focus down the Medusa, then it takes you so long. The axe already got a taunt off, the Bristlebat's coming through.
It's the problem with their entire team. All their cores are ridiculously tanky. None of them are going to die quickly. But Medusa's the one that's doing the most damage, so surely she's what you go for first. It's not easy. This is a hard game now for Druids. They still have a gold lead after that last fight, and they actually have the lead in XP technically too, but it doesn't feel like it just because of how this Medusa works.
Looking at sight, Radiant don't have much up here. Dire have spotted them out.
Daedalus for
and yeah, Daedalus
water.
For Medusa. So they have been spotted here. The ward has been used nicely, and this is going
to
be
her deep. I mean, not quite for having the nuts to go for the big rapier. Probably wisely at this point in the game.
Yeah,
game
could
five
still
the grand
easily
finals.
Die. Yeah. And, especially if you're going for a die into a buyback, and then you are back. There's going to be the Aegis again for Laue. But this Aegis hasn't been that massive yet. Third Aegis now. Two of the Aegises hasn't led to much.
No, they got the cheese this time as well, though.
True.
It's on the center. We saw Nice use it nicely in the last game to prevent his death as they were pushing the base for the win. So what will they do now? They're going to try and force the issue with this Aegis. Looks like they are. Three heroes heading to the middle lane. I can hear it should go dunking creeps.
Yeah, he has got that Aghanim source.
Yeah, it's allowed now. It's not
it's
like
allowed.
Earlier when he dunked a jungle creep because it was killing him.
Well, they've got that. He was able to just use it. Get the back.
Looks like they are going to force the issue. They're going to ping Watson's. He has got a TP scroll. He is absolutely fine. There's no Cloud9 gaming here.
Radiance
the tower. It's a tense moment now. This is going to be where it's all sort of building up for. Good team fight for Druids here, then into buybacks, and then winning that fight again. That's going to be the game for them. Then again for Ichigo just as much. So they are playing carefully. If they lose too much here, they realize that they're just out of it, and this is going to be the end of the best of five for them. So they need to try and make something work. The Blink, Yules can be a nice catch, but they're all staying so close together. Both teams kind of not at this opportunity where they could get caught out. Look at that line. This is the bunker. They are all hiding in the bunker. Just do not leave it. Let's go together when we move. And now they move as one. Well,
Axe has picked up an ultimate orb. Probably seeing a Hex from him just to have more disable on the team. Maybe he'll go Shivas, though. If you think Watson's getting that, so.
Yeah, well, I said about it, but you did go for the Daedalus first, which I think is actually maybe a right call here. Get the damage out now. He doesn't really need that much survivability. If he survived last fight, and...
I think probably his own realization was, they can't kill me right now.
Yeah.
Of course, Tiny himself pretty rich. He can look for another item soon. And his buyback is still up, and he has enough gold to get it. And 2,800 on top. There's not many items he can't buy, depends what he's after.
So look at the XP, we are seeing a drop down to Druids, but this is a close game from over 5k to just the other side, so literally 10k swing would be peak to peak, and we are going to be looking at here, the net worth 7,500.
I said it a lot, but you know, the stress is all, the most important XP is the XP on Medusa, who's nearly level 25 now. She...
Level 24.
She's not quite at the point where she can 1v5, but this hero legitimately can at some points in the game.
Yeah,
Level
24 on her, next hero down to level 21 and onto the centaur as well, so you can see this difference is huge.
I mean, it's not great for it sucks for the Wisp and the Lion that they're low, but they don't mind. They're there to, you know, use their spells and probably get turned to mush by Cleave from Tiny.
Checking the net worth though, when you have four of your heroes, Tiny...
They are far from out of this game.
Their net worth is much more equal.
There's a Scythe, here we go.
Whereas Medusa has that top heavy spread on their team. It just wants to make sure they have that. Medusa being everything. So the pressure is on to Watson's War. Any mistakes now being made by him could lead to them being out of this. So
lethal. The Scythe of Vice has been hit up by Lina.
Yeah, look how rich she is.
She is minted. This is the hardest sacrifice support. You've all been there in pubs and occasionally come gaming.
Shows in the net worth as well.
Yeah, him and Inferno Quay competing for poorest man. Inferno's actually a bit of a 4-star, so I think he's cheating.
I got to say, the Venge has done so much.
It is a hero that works brilliantly in the penalty of items. So
Iceberg has been doing...
He's only died four times still, which is just... It's naturally about the average for his team. It's not really known anymore.
And it's going to be Watson's War, just standing here at the front lines. Farming away. We're coming up to the 15-minute mark here.
Wisp has a Bukuba.
BKB onto Wisp. Took him a while to get, and there won't be a buyback onto him now, but I think this is definitely the right call, because if he has this BKB, he could still get RP'd.
He can't melt like just the spell damage that flies
Laguna
around
the Blade
fight.
As well could still be thrown out, but if he's
if he's using it on a Wisp...
Yeah, you have got a good point there.
I think that's done its job then. That's fine.
That'll be worth it. Well worth it. So... Magnus, double RP usage, we haven't seen any we have seen a couple, but...
He used it during the last fight, that's because he brought back, it wasn't like a...
Yeah, no, exactly.
One of those.
It wasn't just RP into RP, it wasn't the smooth transition, but that's more like a side of how the game's been going. Checking out the actual last hits, Medusa 454 decks, we're down to Tiny 372, so he's still far above. And I got to say, Centaur is keeping up with it as well, he's not falling behind. Medusa has the boots of travel.
So for mobility, push, all these good things. We have officially hit the 5-hour mark of this this best of five here at Insomnia 54. The Emerge Dota 2 Cup is drawing slowly towards its conclusion, but this game is far from a foregone conclusion right now. Ichigo and Druids going toe-to-toe, it's been a fantastic matchup.
Yeah, people say, obviously, when you see games like this, it must be a bit boring. But you think about everything they're doing to set this up can be decided with the next series of events. And obviously, one or two key mistakes then being capitalized throughout the game can lead to a lot of issues here. And there is still...
Looks like Laowai has seen the butterfly and is going for that MKB over the crit, which is what you generally see on the cleaving Tiny. It's a sacrifice, but it's funny, he has finished that item and he still has buyback. So Laowai doing pretty well for himself. His net worth is slowly catching up to the users at the moment because of the map control they're exerting. Ichigo doing their favorite strat of hiding in the base, and it might not be serving them that well right now. Laowai, Tiny, not such a fantastic late game hero as Medusa, maybe, but he's still amongst the best in this video game. So.
Yeah, and like the seed potential, I've probably broke a record, going on about it, but 52 hits is this game.
But he's just been empowered now, and this guy hits for 550 damage. No, 590, I can't add. That's also cleave, double cleave, thanks to empower. And he has an AC which shreds everyone's armor. He is he is brutal. We've been talking at Watson's a lot, but we should be mentioned that Laowei also hits like some bus.
Yeah, Ichigo did get some large catches in after a little bit of a rocky start. Yeah, and if he keeps getting these taunts off now, this could be game-winning taunts.
Back on form.
Just showing how good this for a non-armor spell. Berserker's call is just ridiculous.
We are moving into the late game now as people start buying their boots of travel to combat these flip pushing and the potential base racing we could see as things go on. Of course, if you're Ichigo, you don't want to engage in a base race because broken record, siege damage exists. That the tree is so good at killing towers.
Let's have a quick look at
the site. Oh, hang on. Venge's cheating. She's bought a natural item.
Oh, wow. So not being that selfless at all,
he's
really.
He's actually taking all his buyback, too. Cool.
So looking at the site, like you can see that Radiant are literally just seeing the wall, the lanes out as the creeps move. The Diet do have a little bit more. They'll be able to see this ancient camp here, which should be blocked out there. So.
Hey. Yep. Looks like we are going to have another farm out.
Deja vu.
It looks like we're going to we are in for the long haul, ladies and gentlemen. Make yourselves comfortable.
Yeah.
Send someone you don't, who doesn't
love
like
it.
Send the nearest league player to get you a beer because, you know, they don't really want to watch this.
Are you joking? And, they absolutely love it.
Oh, he doesn't love it. I mean, it is a bit like no flame. I'm going to control the flame. As Medusa picks up the gem. Oh, I, whoops. Hon.
Gives you sight.
Yes.
Fine. Eyes, gems, it's
whatever
all
they are. She's just got money. She isn't quite slotted yet. She's going to sell those face boots and get either an AC.
Radiance top tower.
Depends what Axe is going to go for there. An AC or a Scardy into that slot.
Curry's still rocking the double boot. Hasn't sold it.
Yeah,
and
it's just still kind of active.
Yeah, exactly.
Super round. 491 move speed is pretty good. You've got a pretty long respawn timer on Roshan.
Look at that gold, though. It's obviously going.
Yeah, Druids are controlling the map because Ichigo are hiding in their base.
And this is all because the whole team there for Ichigo, apart from Watson's Water, are just so poor.
Just struggling. I mean, Soodle isn't—he's not inconsequential as he's going. Well, Soodle's going for a basher.
There we go. So yep. Gem being used, and they're just getting rid of this wards, and this is important.
Soodle's buying a basher. Ichigo, we've talked about either a hex or a what's it? Shiva's that one. Mm. As.
Ooh. Oh, blink
forward.
Gets the Yules, and now that's going to be the
nice Laowei's caught.
Laowei will just be cleaving off the axe. He has to turn around to try and save out, but that is going to be a swap. The fastest trout in the land is going to be flopping away, and let's see what they can get down. Element now running, and let's see if Watson's Water can go for more, and they will just take it back. And now Sentinel goes and gets the blink off, and stop. Oh. And now it's the RP onto two. It's a double two, man. And now this is their opening.
Watson's in trouble.
Trying to back out.
Manta Dodge.
And now needs to just keep on running. Needs to just be backing out. And they need to just go. Oh, no. Sentinel Stomp isn't on point. Watson's War keeps the slow, but now going to be killing
the Sentinel.
Turning
it. The buyback.
The buyback. Axe, they're going to be trying to go for it. Watson's
Sentinel's dead.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, the four staff.
Oh, wow. This could be another kill. There it is. It's a double buyback. Now out for it. We've got Iceman.
Sentinel.
Sentinel comes back and gets the stomp up. And it's still
working. In trouble!
Water,
he's down!
What?
Five what man. A fight!
They're all up now!
Buybacks!
Buyback, let's
but
go
round no
two!
More.
They have to go in with just these two. Can these two stay against the world? Wow,
I don't think
five people.
Has it just happened?
This
Druids,
could be it.
Absolutely superb.
No
Soodle.
RPs,
they go on Watson's hex.
Oh no! This is it! If they take him down, this is it! 122 seconds. Soodle still started. Soodle take him on a goose chase. You need to do something big now. Leaders ball back, trying to finish off Chocolate, and they are just going to be taking him down. This is going to be an issue. Druids.
Inferno Quay, what a stun.
With a two man stun. He just wasted the time, but you got 100
seconds. He lightning bolts
the
venge. Take that,
can
nerd.
They get anything, but I'm afraid this is going to be at least. One racks at least two.
It's
gonna,
they can get
defenders.
They can get the base.
Yeah,
I don't think I think Ichigo might have just lost this game.
Oh,
they might have just lost this series. The EU has stolen all our money again.
Oh,
oh dear, that's
they
a
are.
Fantastic execution from Druids though. Oh, the buybacks, someone was selling items to buy BTs.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd say this is going to be Megas up now. This is just Druids.
I think they can get the throne. I don't think there's any way they stop them.
This is so hard.
Ichigo, of course, they're not GGing out. It is the last game
of the
best
game,
five, but I think they can just they can go. Yeah, here comes the siege damage. 60 seconds on the Medusa still.
Oh man, this is absolutely.
Oh, Wisp is dead.
This
again.
Is tier force. This is going to be the ancient.
That's it. GG.
All the winners. Listen to them go.
Having a party.
They did it, lads.
Your winners. of the Emerge Dota 2 Cup.
Oh man, what a series.
54. Holy. Oh. Shit. A fitting conclusion to what has been an epic tournament here. Thank you to everybody who has watched over the weekend and played in the tournament indeed. We had 17 teams at the start.
Yes.
They we only have one remaining. Druids, Ozone, Capture.
Yeah, fair play to Ichigo though. They did play well. They got it to the fifth game. It could have gone either way for a while.
And now I believe we are going to go straight to the prize giving ceremony. It won't take very long. We're waiting on a go ahead. We have a host who will come out and do a prize giving.
It'll be live
on Zoom.
This
has been fantastic fun.
This has been the first live series I ever casted, and it has been phenomenal.
It has been a pleasure to have you here, and I've had a great fun casting with you as well. Hopefully, we'll see you again at Summerland. I-55 is the August bank holiday. I am being told to get ready. Hopefully, Tetra is going to be ready. So we're going to throw it over to him to do the prize ceremony. Thank you again for watching from us. I'm Kenwin, and that's Rusts.
Yep.
Have a good day.
See you later.
First things first, a huge congratulations to our third place team, which was Divine Esports. So huge congratulations to them. But now, hopefully I can get the team's attention because it's time to give out the checks. So ladies and gentlemen, your team in second place, it is Team Ichigo Go Go! Ichigo Go, come up to the Ichigo Go Go, come up to the stage, please.
Well played, guys. Really well played. Close games. Thanks.
Solid. I'll stand to the side.
All right, one more time for Ichigo Go Go! And, ladies and gentlemen, your Insomnia 54 champions, Druids!